It's a very busy morning on the Opie and Anthony show. Getting ready for the eggnog drinking contest. Want to thank Elmhurst Dairy in Elmhurst, New York for all the eggnog. We got crates and crates and crates of eggnog today for the eggnog drinking contest. Also, before we get the contest going, Anthony, I got to remind people it's time for the MacBook Karaoke Contest. Go to www.923freefm.com. That's 923freefm.com for all the details. You can win the new MacBook, sleek and sexy, and it has everything you need to explore all your creative possibilities. Head to the Apple Store or apple.com to check it out. Go to 923freefm.com, 923freefm.com for all the details as far as the MacBook Karaoke Contest goes, okay?
Absolutely.
We got Bill Burns Studio. Bill was telling me off mic that he's been waiting a year for today.
Yes.
Who hasn't?
No, just a whole year listening to Pat Fumunaki puke. That's like the funniest audio ever.
Isn't that great?
I've actually been trying to explain it to people.
That sound is that gurgling, sucking chest wound kind of sound.
A gallon of eggnog hitting a hefty bag.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Always hilarious.
And we learned that Pat Fumunaki's in love with someone that's not in love with him. During the break, I hope the rest of America understands. We're all just walking around going, oh, God, no.
Oh, God,
this is just going to end in a suicide.
Yeah, it's going to be bad.
You can't explain. I was trying to tell my girlfriend about the audio of the puking, and you cannot explain to a girl the beauty of vomit audio. There's no way to make that translate across gender.
No.
The chicks just don't dig vomit audio.
It's almost like Three Stooges type thing or, you know. It's just a girl gene.
You think puking, it's a form of slapstick?
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
It's one of those things that girls just go, I don't get it. It's disgusting. I don't get it.
Why don't you go grow up? It's just stupid.
I watched Jackass 2, and there is a scene where Steve-O was wearing some kind of space helmet thing, and he pukes in it. And it's a glass fishbowl, pretty much, on his head. And he's vomiting into it, and it's filling up with puke.
Oh.
And I'm roaring. It is just the funniest thing. And girls, like, just don't find that funny. I don't know why I find it funny, but it just is.
And she comes running in. She thinks you're watching, like, Sleepless in Seattle. Tom Hanks says something cute.
And all you're getting is this.
Oh.
Yeah.
And laughter.
Guys are pretty simple. By the way, professional camera dude, where are you from?
From HDNet.
HDNet is filming the eggnog drinking contest?
Yes, we are.
We're going to have details on when this is going to air?
Absolutely.
All right, we'll keep everyone informed, but we got a real camera dude in today.
Yeah.
HDNet helping us out today. All right, bring in the contestants.
You know, puking in widescreen. That's what it's all about,
yeah, and
right?
High def, so you'll know exactly what they had for dinner last night.
High def digital video.
Hey, I see some familiar faces. Sergeant Magoo, we got.
Ah, there's Sergeant Magoo. What a show he put on for the Pal Talkers yesterday. Did you hear about this, Bill? Yesterday on Pal Talk, Sergeant Magoo, we had a lot of people come in and audition for this because we want real contenders. Not these slouches that are going to come in and be out in the first two shots. Sergeant Magoo on Pal Talk was home drinking milk, eating sticks of butter with ketchup on it.
Oh, my God.
And vomiting into Tupperware, which he then filled with Fruit Loops, got a big spoon, and started eating. It was fantastic. It was like I was watching Ali back in the late 60s, early 70s, kind of that type of champion. This is a man who obviously wants to win and has what it takes to win this competition.
I like how they gave him the shoulder holster taping of his name.
Yeah, what the hell are you guys doing? Taping name tags on these people.
All right, well, hey, where is that video, by the way, Sergeant Magoo?
Right now, one person that was filming, it got messed up, so we're trying to get the other people to get it up online right now. So.
By the way, not just name tags. I asked for Stars of David. Why don't I get what I...
So we're trying to get it up right now.
Yeah, the mic is a little low. What are we doing over there? We need a little more volume. I'm pinned over here. All right, we also have Dugout Doug is here from a fine website, OAExperience.com. That's how we promote it over here?
Yes, sir.
There you go. He runs a great fan site.
Thank you.
Also known as FBA, but you got to figure out what FBA stands for.
Pleasure.
OAExperience.com to check out Dugout Doug's fine website.
Has there been any dissension in the ranks between the whack bag people and...
I'm all
FBA? Because I see a whack bag shirt over there. I know there's a board altercation going on between Doug's board and whack bag board wars.
It's all in good fun.
Oh, it's all in good fun. Some of the stuff I read sure doesn't look like fun.
No.
You guys are hitting well below the belt.
Who's this gentleman here with the that Danny's got the mic in front of with the whack bag shirt?
I'm Generoso. Oh, Generoso.
Yes, I've seen your name many times.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, the fan sites are fighting all the time.
I mean, yeah, it's just a battle. It's some kind of Lord of the Flies thing. I'm waiting for somebody to push a rock on on Piggy. So, but I'm not sure which one is Piggy. I think it's all of them.
So we got a lot of rocks. We got Whack Bag representing today in the eggnog drinking contest. All the websites, by the way, are linked up on our site, opieandanthony.com. Who else we got we want to talk to? We got Flea back there, I see. He was putting on a show the other day for us.
Yeah, Flea, how you doing?
Doing pretty good.
Skinny little bastard. You think you got a shot at this?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
No,
yeah.
You don't.
You drank. He drank a lot. He drank a quart of milk, and then he drank a quart of half and half, and he drank a quart of heavy cream. He did boof. You did puke, but you kept drinking.
Yep.
You do know if you puke here, you're out. There's no buyback. You can't buy back in.
Yeah, the contest is really easy. These guys are going to drink a double shot of eggnog every single minute until they puke. When they puke, they are out of the competition. How many contestants we're going with, guys? We got what, about 10 or so?
10.
All right, we got 10 contestants. I see Pat, of course, the favorite. Pat from Menaki has got to be the favorite.
But Love might put a damper on his competitive spirit with this whole thing.
He might have to fill his, what? Oh, yeah, girl contest. Thanks, Steve.
Any money going on? Anything going on here?
There's a little action, a little side action.
Side action.
People are betting in their cubicles right now, Bill.
But this is purely for
And you don't condone that kind of activity.
No, we don't condone betting when it comes to eggnog drinking till you puke. Why would we? It's about dignity. It's not about betting and money.
I can't pick a favorite. You need some little skinny Asian guy. They're the ones who always.
Oh, well, you got the skinny Flea.
Favorite was Pat.
And we got a chick this year. I don't think we've ever had a chick in the eggnog drinking contest. You are the first, huh? Who are you?
My name is May. I live here in New York.
Hey, May.
Hi.
Big fan of the show?
Absolutely.
Who put your tape on, by the way? Made sure it went right over your left breast.
Master Poe.
So
yeah.
Master Poe in the parking lot.
I listened to it last year, year before.
Yeah. You really think you can get some shots down?
Yeah, I think I'm...
How many do you think you're good for?
I can probably do about 30.
30?
Are you a woofer?
I'm just a big eater.
Can you puke, though, without problem?
Yeah, I just usually don't puke.
You don't puke. All right. Well, this is something that a lot of people that have never puked...
And she's confusing the audience. She's saying she's a big eater, but you're not a big girl.
No.
No, I'm just a big eater.
And by the way, someone has to say you have a lovely set there.
Thank you.
All the way, May.
All the way May.
Leave all the way May out of this today.
Well, we're just saying maybe she'll be the champ and go all the way.
Hey!
Not like you're all the way May. You're a great aunt.
Nice. They're staying on the back seat that a helicopter could land on.
Bill, remember the show where they went after your grandmother? Was it your grandmother?
Yes, it was.
The abuse was brutal? Well, now they're doing it to my great aunt.
His great aunt is the actual All the Way May, the character that Madonna played in League of Their Own. His great aunt was the actual one.
It's a true story.
She's a nun now to try to make up for all the...
Well, you know
all the gentlemen were off fighting a war, so God knows what she was with.
No, all the way May.
Retards, no. Cripples, and the entire Negro League.
And people with flat feet.
Flat feet.
Bunch of flat
footprints on the Studebaker windshield.
You know how much this could hurt. Don't go there. This hurts. All the way May because she was a really good hitter, that's all. And she went around the bases a lot.
Yeah, she sure did.
All right.
Heard a song about it once with Phil Rizzuto in it.
All right, who else do we want to talk to?
Pat wanted to say something while the girl was talking.
Oh, Pat.
Pat had something. You chiming in, right?
Are you in love with her, too, now?
No, I was just going to say, well, before you said it, I said, I think May's going to go all the way, so.
Okay.
All right, Pat, thank you.
Was your firstborn named 4F?
All right. Wow. Now, Pat was the favorite right up until today, for me, anyway. I would have put all my money on Pat. I think this love thing is going to screw you up. I also think...
I'm filled up with love.
It's going to be in the back of your head that she's making out with somebody else in the hallway. You got to be honest.
What, did you hear something?
You got to be honest. You're going to be really distracted. You're going to be thinking the whole time, God, is she flirting or making out with someone in the hallway as I try to impress her by drinking a lot of eggnog
Why,
today?
What did you hear?
And who's the guy in the blue in the back?
Yeah, now here's a guy that I'm thinking there might be a problem with.
Huh?
Jerry.
What's up, Jerry? What's your story?
Jerry. Just listen to the radio.
Yeah.
Want to drink a lot of eggnog? Puke.
Doug is saying turn around.
Why turn around?
I'm saturated.
Oh, wow. You're,
sweating.
Mike up.
Are you sweating?
Wait,
a little nervous.
You're about 6 what? 4?
6'6".
6'6"? Okay, and how much do you weigh?
460.
Wow.
He's our biggest competitor.
He doesn't look 460, though. You don't look 460.
Because he's a very tall guy.
Yeah, that's true.
He looks 380.
Yeah. Yeah. Svelte 380.
Good now, have you done anything as far as eating a lot? Or?
You think?
Not on a daily basis.
Don't you think?
But I mean...
He only eats one meal a day, but it's a water buffalo.
What do you think your chances are?
I think they're pretty good.
Pretty good?
Yeah.
I did 6 pitchers of beer in an hour and didn't blow.
Oh, wow, Pat, you're in trouble.
6 pitchers
in an hour. All right, Pat.
I like this guy loosening up his neck right there with the psycho haircut.
Oh, my God. Who is this little fella?
Psycho. Who are you?
What's up? I was here last week. I was drinking milk.
Oh, yeah, you're the milk guy. All right, okay. I didn't see
you. He just spiked his hair up
Danny.
A little more.
Yeah. Your video's up on YouTube. It's getting viewed pretty well.
I can find it.
Yeah, it's up there. Just throw Opie and Anthony in the search.
Good deal.
All right, anybody else we want to talk to? I see Sergeant Magoo has his Fruit Loops just in case he pukes.
Yeah, Sergeant Magoo, step up to him, Mike.
Yes, gentlemen.
Yeah, you brought the Fruit Loops now. In case you puke, you're going to reenact what you did on Pal Talk with the Fruit Loops.
Hey, I'm here to entertain. We're going to have some fun today, so I'll do whatever needs to be done. Well, not whatever, but
we'll
have some fun.
Yeah.
All right, anybody else we want to talk to? Anyone else have an interesting story?
Who's the guy in the back there that we
lurking.
Didn't speak to? Your name, sir?
Hi, I'm Shane.
Hi, Shane.
You're
the
Shane?
Dark horses thing. I'm going to win it all.
Oh, really? You think you're kind of just the...
Absolutely.
Richard Dreyfuss.
I'm a closet eater.
Whose colon is it anyway?
You're a closet eater?
I'm a closet eater, man. And me and my friends have little competitions. I always beat them, so I figure bring it out to the main stage.
Really?
Yep.
All right.
That's that faux confidence I've seen so
yep.
many times.
Yeah, we've seen it over the years. It's refreshing because then after a few shots, you ask him, how you doing? He goes, well, it could be a problem.
No, absolutely not.
All right.
I think we're ready, Anthony.
All the confidence. Who are you picking?
God, I want to go with Pat so bad.
But this love thing has got me.
The love thing.
Has Pat won it yet? Didn't he?
Yeah, the first one.
He won the first one.
And he should have won.
Oh, last year.
Last year he set the record but lost the contest.
Oh, he lost.
A weird thing where he took the shot that put him over the top. He had more shots than the other guy. There were only 2 left, but he puked before the other guy puked.
It's all about who pukes first.
Who
there,
pukes
Bill.
First? You got a minute to do that shot, and Badlands decided he was going to sit and wait it out. When Pat did the shot immediately, then Pat puked. Badlands didn't have to do the shot,
and then he puked pretty much right after Pat. It was that close
it was
last year.
So close.
Hey, Pat, what's the record? 71
is seeing the checkered
71.
Flag.
Right. Wait, same thing.
Sorry, everyone's talking. I'm sorry about that. I was yelling over you guys. But the record is 71 double shots of eggnog. That's what we're looking for today.
Do we have an organized squad that can fill all these cups in the allotted time? All right. We own 2 guys? Didn't we have more last time?
I don't like this.
We might want to get a 3rd guy.
Just in case.
Just in case.
If there's a problem on the first round, make sure we get some ready reserve in there.
It looks like they're going to go Christmas caroling.
Yeah. All right. Here's the deal. Just to set it up for everybody at home, it's the eggnog drinking contest. We've got puke buckets all over the studio. We got tons of eggnog. These guys will do a double shot of eggnog every single minute until they puke. They puke, they're out. Until one guy is standing.
And they will be doing it through commercial break.
Yeah, well, we're going to take a break.
We talk to you?
No.
Oh, okay, we didn't talk to him.
Amish beard.
Real quick, what's your name, sir?
My name's Pat.
Pat, and where do you hail from?
I hail from New Jersey.
I was going to say Jersey.
Ah, jeez.
Yeah, Jersey is just, you could see it a mile away. And what's your story?
I go to the Connecticut School of Broadcasting.
Oh, boy.
Good old CSB. And I want to intern here, but I figured this would be the better way of doing it rather than just applying.
And not bad.
All right.
Not bad.
Make sure you leave your info with Steve or somebody,
leave it
after you puke.
Steve.
And Rogan is...
Joe Rogan is joining the party, too. All right, here we go.
Sweetie.
Why don't we get the contest going?
We talked to you enough, Lee. Shut up.
I got one quick check.
What do you got? One quick.
If I lose, Joe Rogan can choke me out.
You're gonna lose, and he should choke you out either way.
Hey Joe, would you choke out Flea for us? All right,
sure. Sure.
Joe Rogan in studio playing Caroline's all weekend long here in New York City. I highly recommend you see the comedy of Joe Rogan.
Do you know what type of that? I am saying that would make YouTube history as far as hits. Joe Rogan choking somebody out, a skinny little bastard like Flea.
A radio guy out on YouTube once.
Really?
Yeah, some guy from Boston.
Wow.
Is it Mark Parento for hitting on you?
Can we choke out Flea before the competition?
It's probably not the best move.
All right. Well, Anthony, why don't we get this going? Who wants to start this up?
Hey, yo, can I do a toast?
Doug?
Can I toast it?
Yeah, Doug out Doug from OAExperience.com.
Hey, the big rich to Solifist. The Solipsist. I can't say the name either.
No one was able to.
God, but not forgotten. Maybe worm food, but we're going to toast you today, Rich.
Yeah, we lost one of our faithful listeners, and he has the worst name to try to say on the radio.
The Solipsist.
But he was a great guy, and he was at every single Opie and Anthony event that we ever did. So, right on, Doug. Good move. All right, let's get the eggnog drinking contest going.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Pat.
Tanya, this one's for you, baby.
Oh, it's over.
Dude, she's making out with someone in the hall. She's not even listening to you.
Oh, no.
All right, start drinking. The eggnog drinking contest has officially begun.
It's going to be something on her shirt, and he's going to go, were you in the eggnog drinking competition, too?
Yeah, they did.
All right, and all you have to do, guys, is drink a double shot of eggnog every single minute. They all got their first shot down, obviously. They're holding their second one.
Refilling. First shot, piece of cake.
Yeah.
This is like Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. You know, the first few questions, what's your name? kind of like that for the $100. First couple, you just know it's going to go fine. But then after a while, you start seeing faces.
What do you think? Third shot or fourth shot? When does it start coming in?
It's usually around...
They'll get up to 10 with not even a problem.
Yeah, anywhere between 5 and 10, you start seeing a face. And that's when you know to get the guy to the mic, because he's going to start going, no, I'm okay, but you see a face.
Yeah, by the way, speaking of that, Anthony, if you are going to puke, you got to be a good sport and help us all out. Make sure you raise your hand so we can get some great audio of you puking.
Yeah.
All right, time for the second shot. And there they go, the second shot.
Good. Well, that minute goes really quickly. Yeah. All right, I'm looking at different drinking styles. Pat just sucks it right down. Flea took two separate swigs.
Yeah,
Flea
thicker
is
thicker than I expected.
It's too small. Is it thicker than you expected?
Yeah, I don't know what's wrong.
It's eggnog.
No, you know what? This is like the first week of like Navy SEAL training where everybody thinks they're gonna make it. Like, I can hack this.
I can hack this.
I'm gonna be special forces.
And by the end, there's 8 guys left out of 2,000.
Right.
Don't you do it?
Don't you? Anthony, you know what we should do? We should take a break. We'll get them to do the third shot. They'll continue through the break, and then we'll see where we're at when we get back with the radio show. How does that sound?
All right.
We got Bill Burr in studio, Joe Rogan, Ari. Everyone's asking about your videos, The Amazing Racist. They're up on opiananthony.com.
Very funny.
If you're wondering. Get ready. Here we go. The third double shot of eggnog. And go.
There it goes. Wow. Let me see the technique. Sergeant Magoo pacing himself. Doug puts it right down.
That's licking his lips, smacking him.
How's the lady doing? She just puts it right down, too. Okay.
Nah, it's way too early. So why don't we take a break? By the time we get back from break, there'll be close to 10 shots of eggnog. 10 double shots of eggnog. It's the eggnog drinking contest on the Opie and Anthony Show.
It's the annual eggnog challenge on the Opie and Anthony Show.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
We now return to the Opie and Anthony eggnog challenge.
We're back with the Opie and Anthony Show. We're in the middle of the eggnog drinking contest. Starting to heat up. The action's starting to heat up.
You meant the studio. It's already, I swear to you, it's already starting to smell like A in here.
Like swamp ass.
Yeah, there's swamp ass going on in here. Somebody is guilty of having
it. There's a lot of guys, they're nervous. They're nervous because they're on a live radio show and they're drinking the eggnog and they're fat to begin with.
Flea.
What about Flea?
Who is it? Flea man has swamp ass?
Flea, what's going on with
who's got a... Flea.
Hi.
Do you have swamp ass?
They're drinking their shot.
Who are is they it? Saying Flea smells?
It's Flea. We need somebody to confirm that.
I don't know. You walked over here about 5 minutes ago, and I smelled the most wretched smell since this whole thing started. And I was standing by the big guy, Jerry, back there. His pits smell so bad, he must have not showered.
Who?
Used any deodorant.
Dude, I swear, I'm smelling things that are really, really bad.
Because he knows he's going to get choked out in about 3 minutes.
It's swamp ass.
Smell I've ever smelt, Flea.
Guess you've never eaten out your
body. Oh, wow. Flea's getting tough.
Oh, boy. Hey, a little smack.
By the way, for the rest of America, Flea weighs... How much you weigh, Flea? 130 tops?
No, I weigh about 155.
Do you?
Ooh.
All right. And you're going to get choked out by Joe Rogan when you lose the eggnog drinking contest, right?
Yep. I will.
All right, and Dugout Doug's not happy with the smell that is emanating from Flea.
Wow. Yeah, let me have that.
And we're starting to spray the Lysol. All right, where are we at? It's the eggnog drinking contest. These guys are drinking a double shot of eggnog every single minute. How many shots have they done, Steve?
They've done 14. Kev's pouring the 15th one now.
They've done 14 double shots
14.
Of eggnog.
E-Rock's spraying Flea down with Lysol.
Hey, let's see how Pat's doing, Anthony. Pat.
Oh, I'm doing just fine.
No problem so far?
No.
Anybody having a problem? Of course.
Flea already?
The cockiest one is the only one having a problem so far.
What's the problem, Flea?
His thing.
Oh. Put your head down.
Too much. That was it.
That was a little bit.
That was like a burp.
What? Wait a minute. We need a judge. Is he out of the...
It wasn't a puke.
It wasn't a puke?
Did he get both feet and bounce?
I think he kind of burped and... Oh, wait. Shh.
Ah, he's out.
No, that's no burp. I tried to single you with it.
Yeah, but you're not drinking it. You can't just hold it in your mouth and spit it out, stupid. It's not a date.
Yeah, that wasn't really puking.
Flea's out. All right, Flea.
Yep.
I'll choke out.
That's it.
Flea is out of the eggnog drinking contest.
Yeah, he wants to be
Flea's
choked.
The first one.
Flea is only here for Rogan to choke him out. Where you going, Flea?
You got to keep your pants on, dude.
Yeah.
Now?
Now, when do you want to do it?
I thought we'd be out.
There's all right, after.
Choking.
Yeah, get out of the studio. We got to make room. So we have to say goodbye to Flea. How many double shots did he almost do? 15?
Wow.
He's out after 15?
Yep.
All right, we're down to 9 competitors.
Anybody else feeling a little queasy?
If he's going to get choked out, he should throw up.
Anyone feeling, full?
Getting a little full. It's very thick, but...
Yeah. Keep going. Very thick. Sergeant Magoo saying it's very thick. It's getting full. Did you eat before you came here?
No, I did not. I planned on eating here.
Yeah?
Shot time, by the way.
Awful.
Shot time, by the way. There he goes.
Eggnog.
Is that the
puke.
Dude that had to throw up with
the Fruit Loops.
The Fruit Loops, yeah.
You,
he brought his Fruit Loops, so he's going to give us a little sideshow later.
You're really going to eat your own puke with Fruit Loops?
He did it yesterday.
He carries those Fruit Loops like Little John Cali. He carries that stupid little cup. That's his thing now. We'll go with some Fruit Loops.
I feel like I only have 55 more in me.
Yeah,
Pat, we heard that last year.
Yeah.
Hey, and he was right though.
Yeah.
Pat did 72 double shots of eggnog last year. We'll 71. See if he 71. Sorry, I keep saying 72. 71 double shots of eggnog. That is the current record. We'll see if anyone beats that this year. All right, where are we at, Dan?
Got another shot in about 10 seconds.
All right, and this will be.
Number 17.
This is going to be the 17th
looking.
Double shot of eggnog.
I think Pat's kind of making a little face like it's a little bit of a problem.
It's starting to suck a little
you
bit.
You kind of winced when another shot was announced.
Pat?
Not Pat from Funaki. Pat Duffy.
Creepy beard Pat.
Oh, okay. All right.
Pat is a...
Loser Pat.
He kind of winced. Oh, loser Ow. Pat.
What about growing up Gotti? How's he doing?
Which one?
The spiked hair.
Oh, there you go.
Good. How you doing? Fine?
I'm just glad I love eggnog.
Yeah?
You really like the eggnog, huh?
A little coat in the stomach now.
And what about a big guy? How you doing back there?
That's the big fella.
Barely feel it.
Yeah.
He's 6'6", 460?
460.
That's nothing for him.
Yeah, okay.
And Doug, how you feeling?
Doing well.
Doing well.
I love the eggnog. I've been drinking it all week.
Oh, you've been practicing?
Yeah, I've been drinking, half a gallon a night. I put on like 5 pounds in the past week.
Yeah. Good Lord. Wow. What is his blood sugar right now?
Yeah. Oh, it's awful.
That would be the real contest.
Been training for this?
Yeah, these guys train. Joe, this is a big thing every year.
This is my first time ever drinking eggnog.
Huh?
My first time ever trying eggnog.
Really?
It's delicious.
Right, Sergeant now. Magoo doesn't even have a chance. He's here to do the Fruit Loop tricks later.
He's on throw up in front of people.
That, we're just waiting for the throw up to happen.
Do
we got a bowl?
Now.
We got a bowl for Sergeant Magoo?
Okay. Oh, a pitcher.
A pitcher. No, good.
Oh, that is going to really sound horrid. I'm looking at Pat Duffy over there, and that last shot really was hard.
I probably got another 5 minutes left. That's about it.
Yeah.
I love nog, though. That's the thing.
Huh?
I love nog. It's so good. It just sucks so bad when there's so much.
When it comes back, you'll be able to taste it all over again.
Right?
Yeah, because I noticed he kind of started drinking that down. He had to stop. He had to, like, swallow. He winced a little and then finished it. So
yeah.
If you're at that point now, you're in trouble.
Minutes, not a lot of time.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
No, I got a little pre-puke belch over there.
Yeah.
Which guy? Oh, which guy?
Just trying to get rid of gases so I can put more room.
Sergeant Magoo is burping, which is a prelude. We all know that.
Just a little air in the lines.
What about our young lady? How are you feeling?
I'm doing all right. I have a sugar rush, so I'm...
Oh, cool.
Yeah?
She's way too much than I'm used to.
Shot, guys. I messed up.
She's got your eyes.
Yeah. Hold on, hon.
Yes, Jimmy.
She also has a burn victim wig hair. Oh, yeah.
All right, how many double shots are we up to? They just did their 19th double shot of eggnog. Joe, what do you think so far? Joe Rogan in studio.
Fascinating so far. Just waiting to see the Magoo.
Yeah, we're all waiting for Sergeant Magoo to eat Fruit Loops and puke.
Kevin's getting weak.
You do realize Joe Rogan hosts Fear Factor.
Oh, yeah, why am I?
So this to him is like kindergarten.
Yeah, you're right.
This is nothing.
I forgot who I was talking to.
It just bothers. It doesn't even bother me.
All right,
wait a minute. In front of me now.
You need diced cow intestines inside the
We've talked to him over the years. Will it bother you when you see Sergeant Magoo puke into a pitcher, then add Fruit Loops and eat that?
Yes, that will bother
me. That will be up there, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
All right, good.
Anybody eating their own puke, that's hardcore.
How about if Magoo ate someone else's puke?
That's even more hardcore.
All right. Watch how many people start puking after Sergeant Magoo eats the Fruit Loops in his own puke.
Especially being all queasy.
Uh-oh, we got a girl.
Uh-oh.
What's happening? We might be losing somebody.
It's way too much eggnog.
Come on, chug it. Chug it. You got it. You got it. Chug it down.
All right, we might be losing the only female in the competition.
Now, there you go. All right. She's still in.
You got to do it for the ladies.
Yeah.
Come on.
We want to see a girl puke so bad.
That's right.
There you go. There's a whole nother glass for you. Right after that one, she had a real tough time down in that one.
The beauty of this contest, it starts off where everyone's like, oh, it's a piece of cake.
Yeah, I got it.
Double shot every minute, and then that minute starts coming by way too fast. What are we up to? This is the 20th?
This is
21st double shot of eggnog.
And here we go. Wow. Okay, she's having a hard time.
Oh, boy.
She's sipping.
Yeah, keep that mic ready, young Dan.
Yeah, they're getting the mics ready and everything.
You know what? You got to just pound it. It's the only way to do it. Oh. Oh. Oh.
Wow, that was hot. Pat's already trying to find his new girlfriend.
No, I just can't do it.
His current one is making out with somebody in the hall. Uh-oh, we got another. We might lose a couple guys here.
Pat. Oh, Pat.
Oh, nice.
I bow to you today.
Did he drink a gallon before he came here?
Hold on. What?
Can I get an intern job?
Oh, that's the intern. Yes, hire him.
Yeah.
Connecticut School of Broadcasting guy is out. What's your name again?
Wow. Pat.
That was Pat?
That's me, Pat.
Pat, we've been doing this for 3 years. I've never seen anyone puke that much.
That was power booting.
That could be the best puke we've seen in 3 years.
Power booting.
Fear Factor for 6 seasons. I never saw anybody throw up like that.
That was some puking, man.
I'll throw up on the street on the walkover.
All right.
Yes. Oh, God, yes.
That'll be fine.
Don't count me out yet.
Dude, congrats. You have probably the best puke sound effects.
That's awesome. Okay.
By the way,
it sounded like it was on loop. But it was just,
yeah. No, that was one guy puking over and over again. By the way,
with the exact same noise.
By the way, we did a really good job there. When these guys start puking, we got to try to stay as quiet as possible. Just,
yeah, it's really like hard, but
it really is hard because it is so freaking fun.
How's May doing?
She's done.
You're out, May.
Yeah.
All right. By the way, the guys had to continue drinking double shots of eggnog during that whole mess. So. Let's see where we're at. We lost Connecticut School of Broadcasting guy that we're going to hire for an intern.
Awesome.
And I guess we lose our only female competitor, May, there.
Oh, May, you're out, huh?
All right.
Can't take
all the sugar.
All right. Hey,
that hairdo is awful.
Jimmy, do you mind if they stand over here to check out the rest of the...
Magoo is teetering?
No.
I thought when she bent over to puke, it was going to fall off.
All right.
Well, just stand back a little.
Uh-oh.
All right, where are we at?
Magoo is teetering. He's got to get that shot down.
We're up to the 24th double shot of eggnog. Sergeant Magoo is making his way to the bucket.
All right.
He has a pitcher in his hand.
I'm trying to hold it.
He's trying.
The bar has been raised so high now.
Yeah.
That was amazing. That was all in him? I couldn't believe it. They kept coming like that.
That was like what? Like 11? I think he puked up every shot that he drank.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Individually.
Yeah, individually. That's what I'm trying to say.
Someone's got to count that for us. I think he puked like 10 to 12 individual times there.
They were all gems.
They were all doozies. Wait till you see the video of that one.
I want that to replace my old puke sound effects.
And people are going to be confused. They're going to go, that guy had to have been one of the last guys standing. What do we got?
Magoo.
Sergeant Magoo, how you feeling?
Feeling a little queasy.
All right. Yeah,
well,
how many?
There we go. Another one.
What are we
up
to?
Chit-chat.
All right, guys, this is the 25th double shot of eggnog in the eggnog drinking contest.
Goes by so
what's the record?
71.
71.
Magoo put that one right down.
Oh.
Oh, my God.
He's puking into the pitcher.
And now you can measure it.
Oh, my God.
He's going to fill it.
Oh, my God.
Oh, it's chunky. Look at the guy turning his back. He doesn't want to see it.
No.
Oh, my God. A little spittle friends on the floor.
He's filling up the pitcher.
It's almost to the top.
Pitcher's full.
Oh,
and the rest of them have to continue drinking.
I think we're done with the puke.
Oh, my God.
Look at all that.
That almost made me puke.
Yeah. He completely filled up a huge beer pitcher.
I'm not looking.
All right, here's the deal. We're going to take a quick break. When we get back, Sergeant Magoo, he's got a pitcher full of puke. He's got the Fruit Loops. They're opening up the Fruit Loops. He's going to do a little thing for everybody, a little side thing for everybody. Oh, it's the eggnog drinking contest. They have done 25 double shots. They're up to 26 as we take a break. It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
It's the annual eggnog challenge on the Opie and Anthony Show. All right.
If anybody's close, I want
to hear what everyone else is talking.
I'm loving it. The eggnog drinking contest, number 3.
Forgot about the bad part of this.
What's the bad part?
The smell. Dude, I had to put a paper towel and then, like, spray it with Lysol, and I'm holding it up to my nose.
It's not a crime scene.
It smells like one.
Anthony, do you want to sip out of that pitcher that Magoo filled?
Shut up.
Magoo filled a pitcher, and I'm telling Anthony in the break that, wait, don't drink it yet.
Yeah, don't. We got to do the big setup for this.
If you swallowed some of that, it would be warm like his stomach, but I guarantee you there's a cool spot in there, like where the stuff that just went down and his stomach didn't even warm. You'd suck it down like an oyster. A cool... like clot of nog from his stomach.
Yeah.
I think I'm having more fun.
You look like he's about to puke.
Dude, Joe, by the end of this, we have literally like 20, 25 people in this room. By the end of this, there's going to be a lot of people puking. I'm having more fun watching Anthony get a little freaked out by this whole thing.
I hate this.
Eric almost threw up
when Sergeant Magoo was filling up the pitcher.
I almost puked, too. I admit.
Did you?
You know what it was? It's the visual of filling up something that is supposed to be sanitary.
Let me give the big setup. We got a guy getting close to puking here. It's the eggnog drinking contest. These guys have been drinking double shots of eggnog every single minute. When you puke, you're out. We're down to six contestants. I think we're going to get our...
Double puke.
Down goes poop in age.
Down goes full-blown AIDS.
It's just as good coming back up.
Oh, no.
We just lost two competitors.
The cocky note chain.
There goes Dugout Doug.
Dugout Doug is out of the competition.
Oh, no.
Shane's going.
Shane's going.
False alarm.
Shane's. Oh, there goes Shane. Wow.
He got a running start with that one.
Whoa.
Oh, my God.
Out of the nose.
Look at Funaki. He's like John Madden of puking. He's just doing the color commentary.
Wow. And the other guys have to do a shot.
All right. Now,
hold on. We lost two, maybe three guys there? Lost three guys.
Three guys right there.
We lost Dugout Doug. Who else did we lose?
Shane and John.
And Shane and John. What shot was that? That was the 30-second double shot of eggnog. We got three guys left in the competition here.
Shane was a victim of the other two guys puking. He said that those two guys puking made him puke.
Well, right. He was facing the wall.
Yep.
Like at the end of Blair Witch. And other people were puking.
Wait, there's only three guys left?
Three guys left. We came back from break with six guys, and right away we lost three of them.
Pat, the big...
What happened there? I missed it.
Came out of his nose.
It came out of his nose?
Oh. And Doug's not done yet.
Doug's vomiting more.
And Doug's now vomiting more.
Warm-ups really paid off this week, didn't they?
Shane was just wiping off his forehead. That's how much is sprayed out.
Wow. He power booted through his nose there, Joe?
You heard it was like...
Yeah.
It's like a horse that just won the Derby.
All right, no surprise. We're down to three competitors, and it's the three biggest guys in the competition. Yep. Pat from Menaki. Who's that? Generoso?
Generoso.
From whackbag.com.
I told him I'd do him proud.
More puking going some of the guys that are out of the competition.
Oh, really? He's coming out of his nose.
Coming out of his nose.
It goes out as much his nose as it does his mouth.
And then what do we got over there? You all right?
I'm good. I'm all good.
Yeah, the 6'6", 460-pound dude is doing fine, too.
Yeah, Jerry doesn't even look nervous.
And so what is it? Jerry Generoso and Pat from Menaki left in the competition.
Hey, anybody want to make $20 and just take a sip out of Sergeant Magoo's pitcher?
Yeah.
A nice warm sip.
Well, where is Sergeant Magoo? He promised us a little thing here. All right, you guys are cool, right? All right, we're going to let the guys continue with the eggnog drinking contest. That's 33, 34?
35.
See how fast this goes? All right, they're up to 35 double shots of eggnog. Sergeant Magoo, the field is the mic is yours there.
Yes, sir.
So what do you want to do today?
Well, I know I'm here to make Joe Rogan puke, maybe. But
Joe, what do you think?
Got a nice full pitcher here of eggnog, which I regurgitated.
Yeah.
So I figure maybe put in a little bowl of Fruit Loops and we'll enjoy breakfast together.
I see the nice bowl of Fruit Loops there on the table. It needs just a little milk substance.
Oh, no.
A milky substance in there.
Look how...
Oh, my God. No way.
Oh, God damn it. No.
Holy Jesus.
No, it's like it's pouring like molasses.
Anthony, it's pouring like rice pudding.
It's rice pudding or pancake
like
batter.
Rice pudding. Look at it.
Thick rice pancake batter.
We might lose E-Rock. E-Rock is losing it over there.
E-Rock.
E-Rock, did you see that pour?
Turn around, E-Rock.
Get on the mic. God. Oh, E-Rock. Oh, he's eating Fruit Loops out of his own vomit. E-Rock.
Right.
E-Rock, you all right?
I didn't know eggnog could clot.
Oh, my God.
Oh, there
There goes E-Rock.
E-Rock's out puking.
Oh, an innocent bystander gets hit by a stray bat.
Let's make this perfectly clear. Yes, E-Rock is not in the eggnog drinking contest. He's one of our own, and he's just puking because he just saw Sergeant Magoo eating the Fruit Loops with his own. Oh, my God.
Well, it was
E-Rock
the whole preparation.
Anybody in the competition. Right.
E-Rock is so pale right now, and his eyes are running with water.
E-Rock, look at how thick that is. Go ahead, Magoo, do that again. E-Rock, you got to look.
Oh, look. Watch.
Oh, it's like snot.
There goes E-Rock.
I almost puked.
Did you?
I had to walk away.
You almost puked.
Poor E-Rock.
If I hadn't.
Oh, no.
We lost Generoso.
We just lost Generoso from whackbags.com. Sergeant Magoo is taking everybody out of the competition.
Oh, Magoo is carpet bombing.
Magoo's like a suicide bomber.
He really is. Oh,
poor E-Rock.
Like look at that.
Look, they're all stuck together. It's like oyster crackers.
Oh, he's just
Magoo. Why don't you top off the Fruit Loops with a little more of what you got in the pitcher there?
How does it taste?
Eric is in the garbage can.
E-Rock is puking up a storm.
His stupid headphones are still on.
God, that is hilarious.
Take us to break, stupid.
Oh, my God.
That is hilarious.
E-Rock.
Are you all right, E-Rock?
Look, he's gonna top
E-Rock,
off.
Watch him pour it.
Look, watch him pour it.
Watch him pour
just
it.
Watch him pour it. Look. Look how thick.
Oh, he's in the garbage.
What children?
E-Rock is puking. He's all the way in the garbage can.
I almost lost. Look at it hanging off the spoon.
Oh, God, it's like snot.
Sergeant Magoo continues to eat the Fruit Loops with his own eggnog puke.
Oh, and there goes E-Rock.
That he poured from a pitcher.
Oh, adding more sugar.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
A guy like that on Fear Factor could have cleaned up, man.
Wow.
Fear
Factor,
yep. You can eat your own puke. What's going to
stop
you?
Oh, look at Eric's. Exactly. He's got snot. Oh, Eric's a mess.
He really is, Jimmy.
Poor young hawk. Magoo, hold that under his face a little bit. Give him something.
What happened, E-Rock?
I threw up my nose.
You threw up your nose?
Out of his nose.
Do you want to eat it?
No.
E-Rock is a mess.
This is the most disgusting eggnog drinking contest we've ever had.
Yeah. We might not set a record. We're down only two guys at this point.
Yeah.
Oh, God, look, there's strings in it. Oh, there's strings that are connected. Oh, no. E-Rock, look at
Every time Sergeant Magoo pours a little more into his Fruit Loops, E-Rock loses it.
Where is that stupid Bob Kelly? Oh, would I be
Jesus. Oh, I invite Bob him, Kelly would be puking like crazy.
Poor guy's in Washington. We invite him, but he's...
We got to get somebody else to take one sip out of Magoo's pitcher. Someone has to do it.
Jesus. E-Rock's got a stomach like Karen Carpenter.
All right, let's get back to the competition, Ant. We got Pat from Menaki, and what's his name, Jerry? I can't really see his name tag. Jerry, right? We got two guys left in the eggnog drinking contest. Of course, Pat from Menaki, who comes into this competition as the favorite.
And very cocky.
And record holder at 71 double shots that he did last year.
Jerry, how you holding out?
I'm doing perfect.
Doing perfect. Pat, how about
right
you?
In front of them eating.
Oh, I'm just wonderful.
You're wonderful. Pat, any ill effect at all?
Can I have some of that when you're done?
You're not going to throw Pat.
Yeah, Pat's not fazed. Sergeant Magoo's trying to eat the Fruit Loop puke mixture right in front of Pat. Pat has no problem with it.
God, that is so
By the way,
heinous.
Joe, Pat from Menaki, a diabetic.
Ooh. He has nine toes.
And he's taking in all this sugar today?
But
you're
a
diabetic and you're taking in all that sugar?
He does get rid of it at the end of the contest.
Yeah, it'll be gone soon enough.
And let me tell you, hearing him let go of all this eggnog, it's like putting on Sergeant Pepper's for the first time. it's magic to your ears what you will hear.
Dude, it's why I'm here today.
Yep.
I listened to it for a year. It was the funniest thing I've ever heard in my life.
Pat puking is the showstopper. It really is.
Well, I've heard it on the radio, but I think seeing it
It's like a Hollywood sound effect. Like, it's so perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got guys in there who couldn't get in there. A lot of guys drove from a long distance and couldn't get in here because it's too much of a mess. Hussy.
Oh, boy.
Oh, he's going to puke.
No. Can we get one of those guys in here? Like, I want to chip in some money and get somebody.
Yeah, I
want somebody.
Hey, we got money. You'll do it. Bucks. Who are you?
He's intern
this,
guy.
This intern will eat Magoo's puke. How much can we give him?
Oh, my God.
What are we communists? All right.
I'm in for 20.
Wait, I chip in 100.
Jimmy's got a bit going. Wait, we got someone else that wants to do it over there. They're getting more people.
I smell puke and people are walking by.
I threw in 100, so.
Yeah, it's really disgusting, the smell in here.
Yeah, it's cruel.
Jimmy, the competition should be the guy to try to keep it down. If they don't keep it down, we go to the next guy and the money goes up.
Okay.
That's what I say we do.
Fair enough.
That's what I say we do.
Maybe I should take back 50, you know, now that I'm thinking of my bravado.
No, thanks.
It's all good.
You know, it's all fun and games.
Jimmy throws down 100. Everybody comes over.
Right, right.
Fives.
I know.
All right,
yes.
Where are we at? Bucks. How many double shots of eggnog
Jimmy
are we up
Trump.
To?
Trump.
That'll be 42.
All right, Anthony, they're doing their 40-second double shot of eggnog on their way, hopefully, to a new record.
Yes, Sarge, I see it. Believe me. He's holding up the pitcher like, look, puke. Yeah, I know.
Oh, Magoo is a good boy.
He is a good boy.
He's a good boy.
He has really added a whole new element to this.
Yeah.
He took out like three guys because
that worked for the show.
Yeah, they were looking at it as they're trying to drink the eggnog. They probably could have gotten a few more shots. I'm not saying they would have won or not, but Magoo definitely cramped their style.
I'm sorry to interrupt you. Did Steve see that?
What?
Steve didn't see that.
Steve, you got to see the viscous.
Steve,
in the pitcher.
You're a tough guy.
On the
come
Fruit
on,
Loops,
Steve. You're a tough
and then
guy.
Watch Sergeant Magoo eat it.
All right, watch this. Here's our
now,
own Steve.
Pour a little on top, Magoo.
With
Steve,
no
watch.
Wait, I can't see it.
Tattoos. Definitely a tough man.
Yeah. When he pours this.
Look how this mess.
It comes
pours.
Out like rice pudding. He's pouring it onto another bowl of fruit.
Oh, it's all curdled and sour.
Hawk?
It's the hanger.
Oh, the hanger. Yeah, there's a hanger on the end of it.
I would
use the word congealed.
Congealed?
And now he takes his little spoon and his Fruit Loops.
I spend a lot of time throwing up after that surgery I had, and this is awful.
And now look, like nothing.
Part of this nutrition.
He mixes
breakfast.
It up.
All right. He has no problem eating this. Here he goes. He's going to have another spoonful.
Check
and
it
there
out.
Goes Steve. I don't think E-Rock has any more puke in him at this point.
Dude, that's real vile.
He's dropping it. He's playful. Magoo is playful. It's falling on his shirt.
Yeah.
He's like a little boy enjoying it.
It doesn't look as nasty as I thought it would, to be honest.
No?
No, it really doesn't.
Hey, by the way, I've gotten word from one of our pals, Wink Wink, that sits to my left here, that Kenny cannot handle this.
No, he can't.
Where is Kenny?
We need him for security.
Get
he has
Kenny
to be
in here.
Kenny, why isn't our security guy in here?
Get Kenny in here.
We don't know half these guys
look
in here.
Look how many people
Kenny
we have.
I want to ask Kenny a question.
All right, Bill Burr,
in the room? Tell him to bring his food in.
He needs to come in here. I just want to ask him a question.
Yeah. Yes, Bill.
He actually requested that I stay in here, and he...
Really?
No, Kenny has to come
here
in here.
Here comes Kenny.
20 years on the force.
The smell is really thick in this room, huh?
Yeah.
Kenny.
Between the...
We need you here.
Lysol.
We feel threatened.
Puke.
All right, hey, wait, let's get to Kenny. Kenny's over here. Club Soda Kenny.
You guys don't realize how bad this room smells compared to the rest of the building.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
I can't even tell. I swear. I'm not smelling
it's
anything
awful.
Yet. And I just finished eating my breakfast, too.
Can you just take a look at this,
why
Kenny?
Why don't you watch the show?
Watch Magoo.
Kenny, this is Sergeant Magoo.
Yeah, get Kenny a mic.
Magoo,
that
is a pitcher. That is a pitcher full of vomit.
No, get Kenny over there.
You know who's worse than me? Roland is complaining in the other room.
Get Roland in here.
He threw him to the dog.
What a tattletale.
Get Roland.
No, no. Kenny, where are you going? You can't leave.
Kenny, stay in here. There.
You didn't even have to torture him. He just immediately told where the platoon was.
Yeah. Yeah. You're
two
ratting
clicks,
him out.
Two clicks to the
right. I don't like it, but Roland doesn't like it either.
What a snitch.
Roland, you're having a tough time? Get on a mic. Just find any mic.
Oh, this is going to be pricey.
Yeah, I just had breakfast, too, and I was like, oh.
Really?
Did you see Magoo pour it?
No.
All right, watch Magoo.
All right, get Roland.
Explain to Roland what that is.
Yeah, get rolling the mic. He's
Magoo,
in front of Sergeant
Magoo.
Magoo's
been out of the contest. A lot of the people puke into the buckets, but Magoo chose to puke into that beer pitcher, which he is now pouring on Fruit Loops. Watch how it pours. That was eggnog moments ago. It is now a biley mess. Oh, he's drinking, Roland's drinking Coke. Coke trying to...
Oh,
look at that hanger.
It's like, now it's like pouring like yogurt. It's not even rice pudding anymore.
God, it's hardening. It's really starting to congeal. And now he will watch this. Watch this, Roland. He mixes up the Fruit Loops.
Yeah.
Come on, Roland. Get a nice eyeful.
Come on, Roland. Here we go.
And, oh, no. Oh, no. Oh,
wait. That's for the competition.
No.
Playing Connecticut School of Broadcasting guy that we're going to hire as an intern. He's out of the competition, obviously. Sergeant Magoo has been eating his own Fruit Loops puke combination. Now, Sergeant Magoo gave the concoction to Connecticut School of Broadcasting guy, so now he's eating Sergeant Magoo's puke on Fruit Loops. Oh, my God.
Eric's about to go again.
Oh, there goes E-Rock.
E-Rock. E-Rock.
E-Rock is puking again. He has nothing to do with this competition. We're finding the weak stomachs among us.
Look at Bill Burr, not looking so good.
Bill, you all right?
I'm all right.
What happened, did you see that? Did you watch that, Bill?
Yes, what got you? The fact that he's eating someone else's puke?
Yeah, I can't even
that. Yeah, that was too much.
Hey, where's Club Soda Kenny?
Right, he's right there. Kenny's here. Hey, wait a minute. Hey, would somebody take... now, that picture is so awful. Would somebody take a sip out of it? Like, without the Fruit Loops? Just a sip. Just a nice, thick, yogurty sip.
E-Rock's down.
E-Rock's down again. Wait, we got to explain because it's just noise for people out there.
The intern took a big mouthful sip out of Magoo's pitcher of thick, viscousy vomit.
He took a Viking swig.
A Viking swig.
And it spilled over his cheeks and chin, ran down his shirt, and splattered on the floor.
That was a victory battle swig.
He just conquered this town and celebrated with Magoo.
The government needs to follow that dude around.
Dude, this kid started as a listener, a competitor. Now he's an intern. By the end of the show, you're going to be like a co-host of this show.
And E-Rock, of course... puked again when that happened.
You get E-Rock's job, by the way.
He's got someone else's puke from his mouth on his own shoes.
Yeah.
Did we explain that he just poured the whole pitcher?
He tipped the pitcher into his mouth, and half of it went into his mouth, which he swallowed. Half of it went onto his chin and his beard after he ate Magoo's puke with Fruit Loops on it.
Your dad's listening?
You raised a tough son of a bitch, sir.
Hey, keep it off the rug. Keep it off the rug.
You should be proud.
You should be proud. All right. You should be a Marine.
Yeah, got right on the edge of the tarp.
All right, let's get back to the competition. It's Pat Fumanaki and Jerry.
Where are you going, Hawk?
We only got two guys left in the eggnog drinking contest. How many shots are we up to?
You have to go back to the days of like Attila the Hun.
Yeah.
To find that kind of disgusting Roman puke rooms.
Just look at E-Rock's face. Look how he's sad and red.
You all right, E-Rock?
Yet pale.
Yeah, my throat is killing me.
His throat hurts. It's coming out his nose, and his eyes are all watery and teary. You look like a basset hound.
Yep, he does. You look like Hulk Hogan just walked away from you.
Hey, I got to ask Joe Rogan, are you impressed?
Yeah.
I mean, you've seen it all on Fear Factor. Are you impressed with this or what?
I'm very impressed with the drinking of the puke. That's unprecedented. I've never seen anything like that. And I bow down. I bow down to Pat Duffy.
All right, right on.
Pat Duffy. Holy mother of Jesus.
Yeah, well.
And he didn't puke after he did it?
No.
Huh? Can someone else do that for the money? Well, we got another kid. You guys want to do the same thing?
What'd you say?
This guy saying he could top what he did?
No, he said he can't top that.
Oh, you can't top that. All right.
How about the guy with the beard, the Nirvana shirt? We recognize him.
Can you top that? Do you think you could drink that?
Beard is going to be a nice touch. The beard, it drooling down the beard.
Do you think you could?
It looks like a fake beard, doesn't it?
Do you think you could top drinking?
Oh, he's stepping in the other guy's puke.
He's in the puke now. He's stepping in it. Do you think you could top drinking that? Puke out of that beer pitcher.
Can I top it?
If you gargle it.
I have no idea.
Can you do it?
Gargle.
You know what? You know what we should do? We should fill up two cups and see who could drink an entire cup, one or the other.
A chugging contest?
Yeah.
You're out?
No, I got it. I'm in.
Well, he's an animal, Joe.
He's already done it. You're, a rookie.
I think we can get somebody to pee in a cup and drink out of it. I think we can get somebody to drink somebody else's pee. I could see that happening.
Yeah, I don't think that'll go through. I don't think that'll make it.
Yeah, no.
I see it happening with the air competition in this room.
Yeah, well, speaking of the air in this room.
I think pee is a step down from...
And I forgot to pee! Stop!
None of it's making it.
None of it's dumping out.
Making the radio.
Let's just say
all
no
that.
Fluid is as vile as vomit, I don't think. Vomit's the worst you can get.
Oh,
anyway.
My God. Smell.
All right, listen.
Okay.
There was a lot of dumping that had to be done there. Okay, we're back to the competition. We're at to what?
51.
51. Now I'm seeing Jerry.
Jerry and Pat from Funaki.
Jerry's taking some deep breaths.
Yeah, I'm getting a little shaky.
You get a little shaky. Really? Pat from Funaki, how you holding up?
I'm fine.
Pat is fine.
Unshakable.
Pat is amazing. Funaki's an amazing athlete, I like to call them.
High-level athlete.
Yes.
Yeah. Next year, we got to do this.
Jerry's sweating.
We got to do this in front of an audience, man.
You're looking a little pale, and I'm seeing like this almost spasmatic, like you're ready to Oh, God. Sergeant Magoo has poured out the big cups of puke.
Magoo is a good pourer.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
Wow. I almost gagged.
It's like this.
Sweaty, you came very close.
It's like this seaweed.
Look at Eric. He won't look up.
It looks like curdled vanilla pudding.
Good call. Curdled vanilla pudding.
Yeah. All right. Here it is. Two equal cups full of eggnog vomit.
Jerry, don't look at this, bro. Brother, don't look at this. I want you in this competition a little longer.
Holy Jesus.
All right, we got the two guys still.
Oh, my.
Is this a clean cup?
Hold on. Here's the deal. We got the two guys still in the eggnog drinking contest officially. We got a little
clean cup.
We got three, like, rings happening here. It's like a circus. We got these two guys on the side. They're going to drink a cup of eggnog, right?
Mm-hmm.
First one,
eggnog puke.
What's the deal? The guy who finished first wins the money?
Yeah.
Jimmy, it's your thing.
I think so, yeah. I don't care. Whoever wants it now. After
whoever finishes it first? Wait, whoever finishes first?
No, because there might be more puke to be drunk. I mean, we don't want anybody rushing. Just enjoy it.
So what's the... Who wins? Who wins?
I don't know.
We need some rules
here.
Nobody.
Yeah, I don't think there's
whoever turns the show off wins.
I think they ought to have a chug contest. Whoever can chug it and hold it wins. If they both do it, they got to do another cup.
Oh, my God. This is insane.
Huh? Another eggnog puke challenge.
I say gargle. I want to hear somebody.
Jerry's rumbling.
Jerry.
I'll gargle it.
All right, what's your name, by the way, Nirvana guy?
Drew,
what's up?
He looks like he's in a spin doctor.
Yeah. Someone else's vomit.
That was your
long time listener, first time puker.
This is really tough. I've never had this tough a time.
Nope. Fan's unflappable, too. Nothing bothers Fan. He's just standing there, tent in his pants. He doesn't care.
I've been fine with everything so far. So far.
Paul R. Nelson shirt on. You show off.
Fan is unflappably psychotic. So I say someone's got to gargle with that puke. Why not? I mean, it'd be cute.
True?
Jesus, Jim.
Oh, whoa.
He just gargled Sergeant Magoo's puke.
All right, that got a little too close. Did they make a mouthwash for that?
Yes, they did. It's called a bullet.
By the way, HDNet is filming this whole thing.
Okay, that got a little too late. That splatter got a little too close. A little speck got on my chair. This must be eliminated immediately, or I will leave the program.
Drew?
It tastes like vomit. What does it taste like?
What does it taste like, Drew?
It tastes like eggnog. Warm eggnog.
Warm eggnog.
But there's clumps in it.
Dude, there's
clumps.
It was warmed up in a man's stomach.
Oh, all right, we got the intern, which, Pat? Duffy?
Yep. Hold on. Jerry's raising his hand over there. Jerry?
What's the matter, Jerry?
I thought it was for a second.
What?
I thought it was for a second.
All right. What shot are we up to? We're getting close. Dan, how many shots are we up to?
54.
All right, the guys that are still in the competition, it's only two, Pat from Funaki and Jerry. They're about to do their 54th double shot. They're going to do 55 right now. All right, their 55th double shot of eggnog.
I think last year Pat did 71.
Yeah, we're getting close to the record now. Pat, how many more do you think you could do?
A few.
Uh-oh.
Oh, there goes Jerry, just put his down.
Pat's eating less because he's losing weight for his girl, so Pat's not in quite...
He's not in shape.
Not in this
he's
kind
not
of
shape.
He's becoming in better everyday shape.
Yeah.
Well, settle down, Pat. Find yourself a nice girl and settle down.
Yeah, where's your girl there, Pat? You don't know, do you?
Oh, what?
I'm going to puke.
Oh, no.
All right.
Oh, my God.
Everyone, this is the big guy, Jerry.
Here comes the bison.
Shh.
Ooh. It's like he's sneezing through his mouth.
Can't get it done. It doesn't want to come out.
Did he technically puke?
Yep.
Yeah, we got a winner actually.
Somebody
what a different sound.
All right, here it comes now.
Does this mean I won?
Magoo's holding the thing under. Hold the picture on it, Magoo.
Yeah. Magoo, you gotta catch some of it?
Yep. Puke into the pitcher, sir.
Jerry is still over the barrel. Not much has come out, considering how much he's got in him.
There's a lot of effort. It felt like a golf match.
Oh, there quiet. He goes. Oh, he's puking into the other thing of puke.
He's adding to Sergeant Magoo's pitcher.
This is so heinous. This is so bad.
You know what's funny? The pitcher was so heinous that him puking didn't even faze me.
I don't know. His puke is different. Lap.
Yeah.
There's something
like
about it.
It's like white cheddar cheese puff.
It's, yeah. It's thicker. It's a cottage cheesy thing.
Yeah, it's had time to really, like, solidify in his stomach.
Yeah. Yeah, the water has gone through different pipes and
yeah.
Oh, left the solid.
Body chemicals have been added.
Oh, God. I like how he's enticing him with...
yeah, with...
The best part about this is Pat isn't even remotely phased.
No. No. How you feeling, Pat?
Jerry.
Well, I'm feeling pretty damn good.
Jerry? How you feeling?
I better. Did it for you, Tanya.
All right, here's the deal. Jerry is the runner-up in the eggnog drinking contest. Pat from Menaki gets his title back.
And not only that, he just finished the little shot. He never had to.
Right.
He didn't have to finish it, but he just chugged down, and he's refilling his cup. Look at him go.
Hey, Pat, you going to go for the record or no?
I already won. Did I mention I was diabetic?
Pat, do you have a grand finale in you?
Funny you say grand.
Wow.
Yeah, where's the money coming from? Do we have to promote anybody, or is it just cold hard cash?
Ooh.
From just the radio station, Free FM here in New York?
With Tanya.
Huh?
With that.
You're going to take Tanya on a date?
Yeah.
Buy her something
driving
nice?
For a master post
yeah.
Hey, let's go to the phones. Pat, what are you going to do? You want to go for the record or no?
Sure, what the hell?
All right, Pat's going to go for the record.
All right.
Let's say hi to Pete in the Bronx. Pete, what's up?
What's going on, guys? Hey. What's going on?
Hey.
Oh, my God. I thought my window was open, and I threw up all over the goddamn car.
Yeah, this
you guys
is...
are great, man.
All right, thanks. It's one of those tough shows. Larry on
really
Long Island.
Really is tough.
Larry.
Hey. Good morning. What's
Larry.
Going on, guys?
What's up?
I'm driving my truck on Sunrise Highway, and I look to my left, and I see this chick, and she's listening to the show. She has to be. Looks like she's gagging and making all these messed up faces. I look to my right, and I can see this dude in a truck, and I know he's listening, and he's laughing his ass off. classic radio. Unbelievable. I'm loving it.
It's been unbelievable today. Let's go to Boston. Zach, what's up? Zach. All right, I love Zach. Let's go to Brandon in Cleveland. Brandon.
Oh, that is... I was fine up until Jimmy started explaining it. And the Viking swig, I had the burps, and I had to run to the kitchen listening to you guys on DirecTV. Oh.
And I say the money has to go. I say that... Would the young intern gargle with the other man's vomit? And I say you get the money. Cause
absolutely.
This kid, nothing phases him.
Yeah, he's a tough competitor.
Just be careful you don't throw up on the walk.
The only way to top this would be if someone put their head over the bucket with an open mouth and let Pat from Munaki throw up in their mouth.
Joey! That's why Joe Rogan is here. Rogan.
That's
Rogan.
The next level, people.
Rogan's going to be at Caroline's all weekend long here in New York City.
Yeah, let's not make this happen next year. Let's make it happen this year.
What do you say? Well, Pat's going to...
That's all those years from all those great pitch meetings. That's all the
experience. Yep, that's right.
It's a
human water fountain.
Well, yeah, Pat's going to get to another level here.
Pat's going to have to get rid of what he's got in his belly because he's a diabetic. So how many shots is Pat up to?
60.
If we can get someone to just lean back, put the head over the bucket with an open mouth.
Who's going
to
lean back?
Can I catch it with this cup and drink?
No,
open mouth.
Okay. Well, we have to go to we
Eric,
can do a break,
Eric can
right?
Hold you up.
Wow, we got to take a break.
You want to take a break now?
Pat, do you think you can do that, open mouth?
You got good aim?
Pat, can you hold out for 5 minutes before you puke?
Sure.
How many minutes do you got to do?
Sure.
How many minutes
break? This is going to be the most disgusting thing ever.
like he's ever done this before. Like, oh, yeah.
Sure.
Pat, how close are you to puking?
I'm pretty good right now.
You can hold out for a few minutes?
Yeah,
Pat's a pro.
All right, here's the deal. Pat's going to go for the record. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll continue with the Opie and Anthony show. I guess when we get back, it's the showstopper that Joe came up with. Pat's going to have to get rid of this. He won the eggnog drinking contest, and he's going to get rid of it as the new intern dude is over the bucket,
Pat Duffy.
Right?
Other Pat.
Pat Duffy. Mm-hmm. All right, cool. We'll do that next. It's the Opie and Anthony show.
It's the annual eggnog challenge on the Opie and Anthony show.
It's the Opie and Anthony show.
We now return to the Opie and Anthony eggnog challenge.
All right. We're back for the grand finale of the eggnog drinking contest. If you're just joining in, Pat from Menaki has won the eggnog drinking contest, getting his title back. He's won two out of the three competitions. He's going for the record, which stands at 71 double shots of eggnog that he set last year. And what else is going on, Anthony? We got the new intern.
Yeah, the new intern.
Pat.
Pat.
What's up?
What's his last name?
Duffy. Pat Duffy.
Pat Duffy. Yeah.
Pat Duffy.
Soon to be legend.
And he is soon to be a legend in this competition because he has volunteered to let Pat from Munaki, who has had how many shots?
67
shots.
He is four shots away from tying the eggnog drinking contest record.
Earlier, Sergeant Magoo, as we know, puked into a beer pitcher. Poured it into a bowl of Fruit Loops and ate it.
Yeah.
Which is really disgusting.
Yep.
And so did
Pat.
Pat, our new intern. He did that.
Step by step.
Ate some of the Fruit Loops, but now he has volunteered. With a little bit of prodding, to letting
if he wants a job as an intern on the show, he's going
to
do this.
Yeah, to letting Pat from Munaki unload his vomit into his mouth directly.
Yeah, because Pat has to get rid of this because he's a diabetic.
Yeah, he's diabetic.
Now he's going to kneel. I would say you should get into position shortly where you kneel on the tarpaulin and lean the head back over the garbage can because you don't want to be balanced. You don't want to fall back and break your neck.
Do we have a table?
I think, what about that little stool there?
A good stool.
Like in Max Hardcore?
Can he sit on that?
Let's
and
get
then,
a stool.
Is that tall enough?
You mean throw his whole back?
Hey, I got to use that. Is that stool good? Put the stool against there. See if he could sit on that and lean his head back like he's at the dentist.
Yeah, because it can't be the back of the head. He's got
Yeah.
That could be perfect size.
Oh, my God.
Okay, that works
like
perfectly.
Hair salon.
Yeah, like he's having his hair shampooed.
Right. There you go.
Yeah, hey, Sam.
Sam.
Could you shoot from that angle?
Yeah, shoot from another angle because if we don't get a view of this, I'm going to be pissed. This is like watching Halley's Comet. Yeah. Oh, you missed it. Yes. You know, you're not going to see this again.
Sam, get in position.
Yeah.
HD Net, get in position. Pat from Menaki, how many shots have you done?
Oh, God. This is actually also like Flashdance.
Yeah.
That scene where he pulls a little handle and the water goes all over him, but it certainly won't be water.
Yeah, you get one later.
All right, wait, where are we at? Where's Pat at?
Pat, 68.
You really going to be able to do this one?
Sure, why not?
Yeah, I'll do it.
You're going to let a dude throw up in your mouth.
Yeah.
Sam, how's that camera battery? Good?
Wow.
Okay. Really.
Yeah, we got like a three-camera shoot going on.
By the way, this is called the baby bird, right? Than came up with the name?
Yeah, Than came up with the name, the baby bird.
The baby bird.
Rogan, of course, that sick bastard, came up with the idea.
Yeah.
He's in position.
For the first time.
Pat's in position.
In radio history, you're about to listen to the baby bird.
The baby
first
bird.
Time in human history.
Which is.
Now, I think some fraternity did this somewhere.
That's true. We're making German pornography.
Right.
This is.
No, I think it was right the other way. He's too high in the air now.
Yeah, don't be all silly.
It's
all
right, because some's going to get on the tarp.
We have a tarp.
We have a tarp. It's fine. Yeah. Pat, how many shots are you up to?
69.
Pat is very close
how
to the eggnog drinking contest record.
Okay, I'm feeling it, though.
You feeling it?
Yeah. Feeling that pressure.
Feeling a little nausea?
All right. We got the new intern, Pat, in position. Pat Duffy.
This is going to be incredible.
And Danny. Could you mic him from the other side?
Yeah,
without getting Sam's way, we got to film it properly.
Yeah. Right. We got to film it properly. Sam, you miss this, you die.
Yeah.
This is very important. Don't go for art. Go for documentary.
Yeah, exactly.
HD, you should get over there, too, just in case.
I think I'm close enough.
You're going to be all right?
Yeah.
Yeah, this guy...
The cameraman's not not into the whole puke thing, but he's filming it for HD.
But
he,
you know, sometimes you got it's like a war correspondent.
I understand.
You don't want to see it, but you're there, and you have to document what happened.
All right, a lot of things going on. Pat, what shot you got in your hand now?
71.
This is to tie the record right here, guys.
How you doing? He's taking his time. It's rough, huh,
he's
Pat?
He's pulling this one over.
Pat, do it for love.
He's got to tell me when to go.
Oh, Pat's ready.
Shot.
All right, this ties the eggnog drinking contest record.
Pat has officially tied it. He is one shot away from setting a brand new record
and
here.
Like a true champion, he's only in competition with himself.
Yeah, only with himself. He could have stopped. He won the competition. He's feeling the pressure. You could see it on his face. He's not as confident as he was at the beginning of this.
No.
He is just going for the record, though. So he can pace himself. He doesn't have to worry about losing.
And the loneliness of the champion left there standing.
Anthony.
Alone.
Yeah.
Also, his belly is really bloated.
Yeah, it is really pushed out.
Because you've
yeah.
lost weight, and you got a massive belly today.
You look like No Filter Paul.
Now, I would suggest to Pat over here, the new intern, our new favorite intern, Pat, that don't move. It's just going to make it worse.
No. You're gonna, close your eyes.
Your instinct is probably going to be to sit up quickly and get out of the way. But that'll just make it worse. Just shut your eyes. Let it happen.
Yeah. Now, wait. Where's Pat Fibonacci going to stand? Because you're waiting. You got a whole bunch
yeah,
of
Yeah, Pat, what's
can.
Your position going to be?
Right there.
So give him like a little hair rinse.
Do a dry run. You got to get his mouth.
No, the mouth, Pat.
Right, well, yeah. The whole head.
But aim for his mouth.
The record.
Pat has just
Pat
set a new record. Of 72. Okay.
72. Wow.
Fantastic.
This kid could not be more relaxed. He's like,
I know.
His heart rate hasn't even gone up.
No.
Pat, can we have a dry run of what you're going to do? Let's say you're ready to puke. What are you going to do? Brace yourself on the bucket, each hand, on the sides of the bucket.
And then
right in his mouth.
Pat. In the mouth, Pat. Right.
Don't worry about the bucket. I mean, we got
it's
the
call
down.
Gay. It's called the baby bird.
It's not gay, Pat.
You are the mommy bird coming back to feed the baby bird.
Feed your young.
This baby's hungry.
Pat, just destroy
it. God. Oh, my God.
Oh, he's going to destroy him.
Please say that before you do it.
Pat,
please
just destroy
that.
His face, man. We don't care about the mess. We'll clean up afterwards.
Oh, right. No.
Tom's tie.
Oh, my God. Oh, no.
73.
Unbelievable.
73 double shots of eggnog from Pat Fibonacci.
Worst thing ever.
This is really, really bad.
He's got that look on his face like those guys in the 80s that were about to fight Tyson.
Yeah.
Just that, oh.
Inevitable loss.
Joe Rogan playing Carolines all weekend long. With the Amazing Racist opening up.
Pat, how are you?
It's getting real close.
All right, it's getting really
real close.
The suspense. All the cameras out. We've never had more people in the studio, by the way. There's got to be about 30 people in here.
And what he's doing is very DiMaggio-esque. This is like the 56-game hitting streak.
Yeah.
73 shots. This will never be broken.
Hey, someone is saying, please center the Pal Talk camera. We got it.
I got mine done.
All right.
Mine's fine.
Uh-oh.
It's Pal Talk 2.
All right.
That somebody's in the way of or something like that. I guess it's the camera guy.
What shot is that?
The left.
74.
Oh, Pat. He's going for more.
He's going for 75.
Everyone's got to pretty much keep their position so
keep going.
The cameras and everybody can see.
Puking all over the place.
75.
Just about every city in America. And in Canada, thanks to XM.
He's just drinking now. He's up to 76.
Uh-oh, here we go.
Here it goes.
Oh, my God.
I almost wet myself. I swear to you. I'm laughing so hard.
We lost Jimmy. He's laughing so hard. He ran into the corner.
Yeah! A thunderous round of applause.
Down goes Pat. Down goes Pat.
He's wearing puke blackface.
That was the greatest moment in radio history, period. It's impossible to top that.
Trust me on that.
How can you top that?
Trust me on that.
How can that be topped?
We are announcing our retirement right now because that is it.
How can that be topped?
Wow.
Joe.
That can't be topped. That was the craziest thing I've ever seen in my life.
That was insane.
Can you believe you were watching that as it was happening? I cannot believe I saw that. Holy
Jimmy, what happened?
I was filming it on my camera for posterity.
Yeah.
It was like Zapruder. And as I got a hit, the smell hit me and I almost threw up. But I mean the smell.
Dude,
that kid is
the best part. When Pat, our new intern, turned his head sideways to get some of it off of his face, and Pat puked right in his ear.
No, the best. What about when he opened his eyes and all of a sudden there was just these two clear dots in the middle of this cake batter?
Listen.
He's going. He keeps going.
All right, listen.
Oh my God.
I'm watching it on Joe Rogan's camera phone. Oh, my God. I'm crying.
It's the worst thing I've ever seen.
Look. Here, this is what we... Hold on, Ant. We got to do this because everyone's asking what the hell happened. All they heard was the reaction. So, Pat Fruminaki, what shot was that? The 75th? He did this 75th.
You got to get that.
Hold on. Let's do this, Ant.
Oh, the cleanup.
He did his 75th double shot of eggnog because people aren't sure exactly what happened, okay? He immediately lost it. We had Pat Duffy leaning over the bucket... And Pat just unloaded everything that was in his stomach. I've never seen anyone puke more volume in my life all over Pat Duffy's head. He's still cleaning off his head. It's pouring out of his hair still, the puke.
He just shook his head like he got out of a pool, you know, when you have stuff in your ear.
There was no way to describe it as it was going on because it was the reaction in the studio was just amazing.
Oh, my God. I defy that clip. To not make the number one downloaded clip on
YouTube. We're going for number one download on YouTube.
What the hell are you going to watch that's better than that?
That clip will be up on YouTube, what, within a day?
I'm sending that to my website. It's going to be at joerogan.net in about 10 seconds.
That's got
to
be, yeah. That has to
be online
immediately.
It's going right now.
Brilliant. Oh, look, Joe is uploading it as we speak at
Technology.
JoeRogan.net?
Yeah, JoeRogan.net. It'll be up in my phone camera slot section.
Right.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
I was watching it, like, and it was like it was an out-of-body experience because I was like, I know what it's like now to watch a murder happen.
Dude.
You're watching going, oh, my God, this isn't really happening.
All right, it's Anthony. Because people are like, all we heard was you guys screaming. You got to understand, it was so unbelievable. We stepped out of being radio hosts and just watched. All right.
When I suggested, I did not think he was going to take it up.
I'm telling you right now, Ann and I have been doing radio for 12 plus years. That is the greatest moment that we've seen
in
studio. And we've seen it all.
That he was leaning back, his head over the garbage pail, sitting on a stool like you would getting your hair shampooed at a salon.
Oh,
that's the exact stance he had. Pat was on the other side. Where the sink would be, where the faucets would be,
The mama bird side.
Yeah, the mama bird side. Pat, the intern, mouth opened, and then Pat Fruminaki just let loose a virtual waterfall.
Have you ever seen anyone puke more volume?
No.
I can't even describe
it was a waterfall.
How much came out of them.
It's uploaded. It's at joerogan.net now. There's a little section in the upper left-hand corner that says latest camera phone shot. It'll be a video. It'll be on Text America.
Good luck.
But you can find it on joerogan.net.
Good luck. You just crashed your site, I'm sure.
I don't care.
Wow.
I got it on my cell phone. I don't care.
Oh, I can't believe I saw that.
Yeah, Steve, get that video up on OpieandAnthony.com.
And it kept happening and happening. It wasn't like it happened and then it was done.
Right.
It went on and on.
And
the volume, it was more each time until he was completely covered. The mama bird. Look at this disgusting. It stinks.
Pat was standing there, and he would just open his mouth, and it shot out of it. It almost looked like fake puke, like it was being done with a hose, like Lexi says, when she's opening her mouth and puke shot out.
And like Joe said, simple as this, we just raised the bar. I guarantee that is the greatest moment in radio history right there as far as just over-the-top stuff.
Oh, my God.
I guarantee. When you see this video on YouTube and opiananthony.com, you're not going to believe it.
Oh. I'm uploading a second video. I got two videos.
He never puked himself.
Yeah, you didn't puke, right, Pat?
No. You are
Pat Duffy,
a trooper.
Pat Duffy.
He's our new...
Save it for the walkover.
He's our new intern.
That dude is a savage.
Give him the money. It's not much money, but give it to him. That's his money.
Oh, yeah.
Here, Pat.
Yeah.
Now, that's a way to apply for a goddamn job.
Absolutely.
Oh, my God. You're hired.
He deserves health insurance after that one.
Yeah.
Dental, even.
What are your references? He puts his head back and opens his mouth.
Wow.
A little thing called the baby bird.
Yeah. You ever hear the baby bird? Me.
Greatest moment in radio history?
Yeah.
Hey, Joe, you know football?
Nose.
You don't know football? I got to get these.
Do your radio picks. Let this new boy, Pat Duffy, do your picks.
Yeah, I got to do my football picks for this week.
New
football
star.
Picks sponsored by Dish Network. More football for you. Better TV for all. Call 1-888-GET-DISH. That's 1-888-GET-DISH. Dish Network.
Total respect.
How about we do this as a group? Jets, Packers. What do we think?
Jets.
Yeah, let's go Jets on that. All right. Jaguars, Dolphins.
Got to be the Dolphins.
Yes, Dolphins are playing at home. Got to go Dolphins.
Maybe, but the Jaguars.
we got the Falcons and the Redskins. That's a toughie. Redskins at home?
Falcons. I hate the Redskins.
Thank you. Falcons.
Falcons?
Better team. Michael Vick.
All right, we'll go.
Yeah, but then again, he's giving the finger to his own fans. I love him.
All right, let's go Falcons. So far I got the Jets, the Dolphins, the Falcons. Here's the biggie this week, Cowboys, Giants.
It's going to be Cowboys.
Cowboys on a roll.
He's going to run through that stupid Giant defense.
And then finally the Texans and the Raiders.
Ugh. Definitely Denver.
Yeah, I like Denver, too.
Denver? Houston or Oakland? I say who cares, but I'll go with Oakland.
Yeah,
Oakland at home. Oakland at home, all right?
Wow, does it smell over there, Steve?
Oh, it's football. Football picks sponsored by Dish Network. More football for you. Better TV for all. Call 1-888-GET-DISH.
Steve has puke on him. Puke on the wires.
There's puke all over me. Is it
smelling bad, Hawk?
People are calling it pukaki.
Hey, we're going to walk over to XM.
Yeah.
And we have some, the boys will be drinking some eggnog on the way.
Yeah.
This young go-getter, Pat Duffy.
Yeah.
Hopefully won't throw up on the walk over because we'd hate to see that on 57th Street because that would look really awful.
Yeah.
We'll be filming.
Well, I'm now looking at the text that was coming out of Pal Talk because the people watching it on the cameras, and I've never seen so many written. Ever. People are just disgusted. Other people just throwing in random letters, like they just slammed their keyboard and hit send.
You know,
they were stunned.
Dude, for the first time, I think the reaction said it all. I mean, we had over 30, maybe 40 people in studio just losing their minds. Jimmy, like, I didn't even know where you went.
I stood on the couch and was filming with my own camera.
I fell on the floor. I was laughing so freaking hard. I was crying.
I thought I was going to wet myself.
No one else was puking.
I got right next to it to get it on my camera phone.
Yeah.
I didn't even throw up. I was so transfixed by the moment. I couldn't believe it was actually happening. It was like an alien abduction.
You are a trooper, man.
And the round of applause was incredible.
Yeah. It's called the baby bird. Thank you, Than, for naming that fine
Rogan
little stunt.
It,
yeah.
And Pat for being Pat and other Pat for being Pat. We have two Pats.
Yeah, we got
I've got to hear that again when we get over
yeah,
there.
Yeah, we will.
I've got to hear the clip.
Listen,
let's get out of here.
We got to get out of here early because they got to clean up.
Yeah, they got to clean up.
All right, Joe Rogan at Caroline's all weekend long. I'm telling you right now, Joe Rogan's comedy is amazing. Make sure you check him out at Caroline's if you're in the area. And you got the amazing racist with you, right?
212-757-4100. You're there tonight, tomorrow, and Sunday, right?
Yeah, yeah.
How many shows? Two, and one?
Two, and one, yeah.
Rogan will sell out, you idiots, so call.
Bill Burr, anything?
What do I got? South Beach for New Year's.
All right, very good. And we'll continue over at XM. Monday and Tuesday, broadcasting live from West Palm Beach, Florida. We're leaving for West Palm right after the second half of the show on XM today.
West Palm Beach, that's where I'm going to be.
Oh, right on. And we'll be at the bake sale that they're doing down there tomorrow. It's an all-day concert festival, whatever.
Hurry up, get me out of here.
All right, we got to go, guys. Thank you so much. Don't forget to to check out the videos on YouTube. Just throw Opie and Anthony in the search engine. That should happen within the next day or so. And also, opieandanthony.com. A little secret, because when Sam throws these videos up on YouTube,
yeah,
you have to wait in the search engine for about 24 hours.
Yeah.
His account is OA Videos. OA Videos. You can get a sneak peek very early on. OA Videos. All right, that's for the tech people out there. They'll figure
great
it out. Hey, guys, thank you so much. We'll see you when we broadcast live from West Palm Beach Monday and Tuesday.
Wow.
Awestruck.
I'm awestruck at what I just saw. I'm happy to breathe fresh air. And Bill pointed out there are three buses across the street, like, spewing exhaust. And to me, it's fresh air because it stunk so fucking bad in that studio.
This is going to be the video that everyone talks about as far as the Opie and Anthony show goes.
Yeah.
We've made some great videos lately. This one is going to be... It might beat Bill Burr's video, by the way, is the top Opie and Anthony video on YouTube.
Hit counts.
You're in trouble, Bill.
Oh, yeah.
You're in trouble.
Going down on this one.
And there's no reason why mine should not be number two by 9:30.
I can't even explain it.
Baby Bird.
It's called the Baby Bird. Joe Rogan came up with it. Than named it. And it wasn't disappointing. We had Sam's camera work was unbelievable. I saw it. It's amazing how much came out of Pat Fromenacci. That's the first thing that
and
comes
how,
to mind.
How,
it was like a pail.
A pail.
Yeah.
There you go.
Every
and
time he puked.
Every time, right.
How Pat, our new intern, Pat Duffy. How he took it. Just laid there and just took it.
Like a man.
Like a man.
Like a man
takes it. He turned his head at one point.
No, like Pat Duffy.
Like Pat Duffy. And he was going, trying to get it out of his mouth and nose and eyes.
Yeah.
And as his head was turned, Pat laid a volley of puke on the side of his head.
Yeah.
That just covered his entire head.
They're both named
so
Pat, so you got to go Mama Bird and Baby Bird.
Mama Bird and Baby Bird.
Right. By the way, usually we have security walking us to XM, and of course we do today. They have to walk with Sam in that camera.
Very valuable tape in there.
Somebody walk with Sam today.
He needs to handcuff that to his wrist.
Yeah, no
right.
Kidding, man.
Would you be mad at him if he dropped it in the tape?
Oh, God, in a puddle.
No.
That would be our luck, to be honest with you. Sam, what are you waiting for? Get to XM. Get that online.
Be careful with the camera.
Camera. Why don't you put that tape or something, take it out. Sam's a good one. He took it out already. He doesn't have it anymore.
All right.
Kid's all cock.
All right, want to start the walk. We got a huge crowd here today. Everyone say hi.
Oh, yeah.
Very, very nice crowd. I think they're seeing us off. They kind of come out when we're hitting the road.
Yep.
Or they think we're about to be fired.
Yeah.
True.
Hitting West Palm Beach after the show today.
Yeah, Tom Chiasano looked none too happy.
I talked to him after the show. I got to be honest. He was cool.
Was he?
He was pretty cool about it. A little worried about how we left the studio, but
it was
not our problem.
Fucking mess.
Oh, yeah. He's the one who's got to listen to the complaining.
Yeah.
Those
yeah,
poor
the next
bastards
show that comes
who've got to
in.
Come in next.
JV and Elvis are going to go in there and just be like a little pissed off at the smell.
Dude, how awful that is. We got used to it because it happened slowly.
Right.
Can you imagine walking into that and just smelling that? And having
it was worse down the hall because of the fan.
Yeah.
You know, I got to say it. The eggnog drinking contest gets better and better every year.
Every year.
This was by far.
Top it.
Oh, yeah. Screw Andrew today. Yeah, go fuck yourself.
Andrew, how are you?
How you doing?
Treat yourself.
Gilligan.
We'll see you at the homeless shopping spree.
He does have hair like Gilligan.
He does.
Yeah.
Gilligan.
I'm the same living situation.
Dude.
Except he does. He needs a little fake palm tree out there.
Hey, we should get that for him. So many highlights. So many highlights.
The first puke, that gurgling sound, and that again was
Pat
was
Duffy.
Pat Duffy,
his
our
name
new
is Pat Duffy.
Is anyone going to puke on the walkover?
I would love to see the reaction of people if we get some.
Hey, does anybody have to puke? Anybody sick?
No, they're all kind of
everyone's all
there.
Dry.
Yeah. All right.
Fuck, I would have loved to have seen somebody drink some eggnog.
You guys had a Congressional Medal of Honor.
I know. He should get it.
So he really should.
So we had Pat Duffy that started the festivities as far as the highlights go. And then, I mean, Sergeant Magoo. You almost forget what Sergeant Magoo did in this competition today. Just amazing, amazing stuff with the Fruit Loops and the puke.
It was a total team effort.
It was incredible.
Joe
you
got to
come up with a new the Pat Duffy Award.
Yeah. Joe, your thoughts once again.
Huh? your thoughts on what you just saw.
I'm blown away. I feel like I just saw like someone do something that's impossible. I feel like I saw someone fly through the air, breathe underwater.
Someone inventing a new kind of music.
And yeah, Joe Rogan, remember, fear factor. This guy's seen a lot of really heinous shit. And
that was way past anything I ever saw in Fear Factor. Way, yeah. That was in another dimension.
Yep. Another dimension.
Beatles. You just saw the Beatles.
Yeah.
Beat that.
The Beatles. Of
that was
Puke.
The first talkie. You just saw the first talkie.
Amazing. All right, making our way to
Patty. Patty.
Oh, Patty.
The only thing that would be better is if we dipped her in that can.
Oh, that would be Patty.
Yes.
Just a head first right into the garbage pail full of puke.
Oh, my God. Let me. Can I get through here, Joe? Somebody smells of puke.
Yeah.
Oh, really? Everyone, I wonder why.
There's only four of us that don't.
God, we got a lot of people out here today. A huge crowd doing the walkover.
All right.
Which way you want to go?
Well, that's flashing. We'll go straight.
We'll go straight today. We have Sonny Forelli out here and Flea and
yeah, a lot
no
of the regulars.
The whole dirty crew.
General Bam's out here. Looking
look
around.
The bus stops.
Happy typing yeah, girls out here.
Son of a...
Oh, thank you.
Huh? Waiting for the light to change. All right, we're good.
You're waiting for the bus to get
yeah, everybody
out of the
does
way.
Smell like puke
we
out here.
We gotta get on the elevator
it's
with
disgusting.
Puke guy. We have to get on. I want to see people's reaction when he gets on the elevator.
Oh, yeah.
Puke guy. We
just reeking.
We have to be on the elevator. We have to tough it out.
Reeking as puke. Oh.
By the way, the video will be up on YouTube. A little side door action because stupid YouTube. You got to wait like a day for the video to be available. Sam's account is OA Videos.
I was wondering what the smell
OA
was.
OA Videos.
It's the picture.
We got to get. Where's the picture?
It's hanging off of Sergeant Magoo's back pocket.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Here we go.
All right, we got to. I want to see the faces when Pat Duffy gets in the elevator.
And just
smelling.
Reeks.
Oh, look at the dogs.
Kick them.
I'm going to cook them. Fucking rotten Asian.
Wow, what a day.
Jesus, Bam.
That, I don't know how you top something like that. Next year, what are we going
to
do?
Next year, we got to bring the eggnog drinking contest to the public. We have to do that.
Imagine the baby bird in front of a couple of thousand people.
Oh, by the way, Ant, good description when you were talking about Flashdance.
Yeah, that's how he was laying.
If you know that old movie with the water coming down cascading, it was that much puke.
That's what it looked like.
It was that much puke. Right?
Flashdance, yeah, the water
Jesus.
Scene.
What a smart outfit. Oh. She looks like a fat white tiger.
I wish a lion would come out and bite her neck.
A zebra.
Exactly.
A fat zebra.
Oh, that was the fucking worst. A white like and black striped hat and coat.
Awful ghetto.
She was dressed like she was on the Flintstones.
All right, what are we going to do? How are we going to get all these people up today?
Well,
huh?
I'll organize it.
That's Kenny.
You realize they're bringing the smell of puke with them.
All right,
just
everyone.
Throwing that out there.
Hold on, everyone listen up. Kenny?
Yeah.
Kenny, your speech.
Yeah. Listen, people, pay attention. If you want to come upstairs, I will discreetly pick some of you to come upstairs and watch the Opie and Anthony radio show on XM Satellite Radio.
The greatest radio show!
That's correct. The greatest radio show of all time. Thank you.
All right. Kenny will take
was
care of
you. Was he asking
guys.
For
Thank
sexual
you.
Favors there?
Yeah, I think so.
I will
so.
Pick you discreetly.
Discreetly? I don't think that's the word he was looking for.
All right. Heading toward the elevators. We'll see you guys upstairs.
Unbelievable. Has anyone seen Pat yet? Usually
no.
He spends about an hour in the bathroom after the eggnog drinking contest, shitting and puking.
Unbelievable is all I could say.
You know, if Pat wins it again next year, that's a dynasty.
Treat.
It's a dynasty.
Well, he's won two out of the three. Two out of the three. And the new record is 75, I guess.
That's the record.
75. There were so many highlights. We were remembering all the highlights in the elevator. Like, we almost forgot that E-Rock was puking through the whole thing.
Oh.
And he wasn't even in the competition.
The
that was
chugging.
so much fun.
That was so unbelievable.
The chugging of the puke.
Just Niagara Falls. It was like standing under a waterfall of eggnog puke.
Sam is already in front of a computer working on the video, so.
Yeah, JoeRogan.net, it's all uploaded to the front page now. It's on the front page now.
Let's,
two videos from my camera phone.
Let's say hi to Lucas in Arizona. Lucas.
Hey, what's up, O&A?
Hey.
Well, thank you guys for giving me the best birthday present ever.
Yeah. Oh, you like that, huh?
Yeah, love the puking.
Love the puking.
Thank you, sir. And our, they're never satisfied. Rogan never choked out Flea. We forgot all about
relax. How do you top that? If Rogan puts puke on his cock and chokes Flea with it, there's no way to follow that.
Flea in the ass with puke on my dick while I choked him unconscious.
Mm, I like it.
While he threw up into Pat's mouth.
Might have to come back next year.
I don't know. In front of an audience.
Next year, we do it in front of an audience. Well, we had an audience today. We had about 40 people. We're talking, in front of 1,000 people.
That was repugnant.
I've got to hear it because I was in the moment. Hard to, like, really sort it out. I want to hear it so I know what the listeners heard.
Yeah, well, do we have the audio ready to go?
Not yet. No.
Not yet.
And by the way, we have to get a couple of the interns in here. Something going on.
Yeah, we'll figure all that out.
We're a problem. Probably.
Are they jealous of the new star?
I don't know.
Maybe that's it. They're feeling the pressure.
Exactly.
There's no way you're going to top that guy.
No.
That guy, he didn't even throw up. He had his mouth wide open. He turned to the side. Then Pat threw up in his ear.
And then all over his head and face and chest.
And you were saying he opened his eyes. It was like a raccoon.
Yeah, he looked like a raccoon. And he's like spitting. And bubbles were coming out of his nose.
I just never thought anybody was going to do it.
No.
Someone is going to think
that's anyone do it?
Someone's going to think it's a fake video. Just how his
mouth was so wide open. It was like a broken fire hydrant.
And it reeked.
Where do you go mentally to block all that out and just be like, okay, it's just warm liquid.
So, that Pat Duffy is a sick fuck. That kid is completely out of control.
We all know
that's your guy. There's not a lot of guys like that. That's a rare find.
I'll tell you, an intern like that comes around once every 20 years.
Right. Yeah.
It's like the Muhammad Ali of interns.
Yeah.
That's the guy you want on your
Jimmy
team.
Jimi Hendrix.
He's Cassius Duffy.
We all know his name. His name is
Patrick
Duffy.
I'm
trying to think.
Rogan's site, just don't even bother going there.
Is it crashed?
No, I can't even. It won't load.
You're a smart man, Joe Rogan. You're a smart man. I'm trying to think. Other things we've done that comes close to that, and we've seen it all. We've had blind guys boxing.
That was
where a guy popped out his eyes and was boxing.
Cigarette smoking out the pussy.
Out of the pussy. Just
trying to make a cell phone call with a girl with a phone up her pussy.
Yeah.
To see if we got reception.
Of course, the 55-gallon drum challenges.
55-gallon drum.
That's going to be a
shooting a bottle rocket out of her pussy.
Oh, shooting a bottle rocket out of your pussy.
That's still.
This might go right to the top.
Yeah, I think it was. I've never heard of anything that crazy.
A lot of those videos are up on YouTube, by the way. The ones where
is anybody?
About
I mean,
right now.
Who's going to rip that off? Is somebody going to rip that off? Is some hack in like Kansas City going to rip that off?
How can you? Where are you going to find someone that's going to agree to that?
Yeah.
That was like the stars aligned perfectly. We were having the competition.
Yeah, that's
we
like
had a guy in there that was willing to do this.
And that'd be funny if they try to rip Baby Bird, like the little seagull. We came up with it first.
Little seagull,
the penguin.
Yeah.
The Baby Bird.
Dude, that video is going to be just viewed like.
It better be, or else YouTube is
stupid.
Phony.
Even if you get someone to agree to it, you also have to have someone there who's willing to projectile vomit.
Vomit. You have to have him had enough in him that he can vomit that much.
75 shots.
Someone has to drink 75 shots of eggnog.
Yeah.
And every year we try to do the math, and every year we fail. Figured out 75 double shots. How much eggnog is that?
It's got to be a gallon.
Maybe a gallon.
He said that you can't drink a gallon of milk. He told me that I could. It was impossible to drink a gallon of milk.
We've done it.
Really?
Yeah.
In an hour?
That was a perfect storm.
I thought it was impossible. I've heard it's impossible.
We've heard the same thing, but we had a guy do it to get into this contest.
And he kept it
Pat from Munaki.
Well, then he puked.
Champion. He's a champion.
A true champion.
Where's Pat from Munaki?
He's still puking and shitting somewhere. That's what he does after
like
the competition.
Disgusting.
He's icing down his larynx.
Where's Tanya? You think they're going to make out after this? I love you.
Can I puke on you? Some people are saying they've seen the video already.
probably off Joe Rogan's site, and they're saying best video ever.
He's showing up to the Victor Scarlett spoils, trying to fill her up.
Yeah, as his fucking as his pants are down around his fucking 9-toed feet, and he's shitting in the fucking free FM bathroom,
puking sloth.
Yeah,
let's go to Corey in Montana. Corey.
Hey guys, what's going on?
Hey.
Hey, I just thought you might owe me breakfast because I left mine laying on Highway 261.
Yeah, I think a lot of people are puking.
That was coming in like crazy. People puking all over
how
the
many,
place.
What do you think we got? How many people puking? Maybe 100,000?
Yeah.
I bet you got 100,000 people puking.
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 When you started describing that viscousy, stringy stuff out of Magoo's pitcher, I lost it.
That's when I never, like, get nauseous at these things. That I've seen them. You know, I consider myself a war veteran of this kind of thing.
Yeah, absolutely.
Been in it. Been in the trenches. But I got that tinge of a choking feeling in my throat at one point when Magoo was pouring the beer pitcher of his own vomit on top of his Fruit Loops, and it made this stringy,
yep,
like, white and yellow goop.
It's like
and then
seaweed.
A big blob just went bloop and fell out in it. It almost, I got like a tinge of tightening up in the throat.
That was the most disgusting thing. Like, the puking on the head was just like...
It was so amazing.
It went beyond
yeah, it
gross.
Was, it was so amazing, you didn't have time to think about it on the sense of it being gross. You just were amazed you were watching it.
Yeah.
It was one of those things, like, you know...
Has that ever happened before?
The moon landing. It was like watching the moon landing.
I can't even talk, dude. I am ruined. By the
dumbfounded.
I have nothing to say.
You had to remove yourself from the situation.
No, I was on the red couch standing there filming it.
Yeah.
With my camera.
It was just...
When the smell hit me, I literally almost just vomited involuntarily. That smell...
Now, that would have been a real topper if Jimmy Norton himself would have puked.
I was very close to it, but I hate puke.
What was amazing was how it escalated slowly. Like, yep. First, Magoo threatened to eat his own puke. And everybody's like, okay, is this guy really going to eat his own puke? And then he throws up into the pitcher. Oh, Jesus. Now he's pouring the pitcher into the Fruit Loops in there. Now he's eating it. Now fucking Pat is eating his puke. You got to be shitting me. And then the other guy jumps in like he's going to be the fucking champ. And they start gargling. I mean, it just kept going.
Oh, I forgot
the
about
the Viking chug.
The Viking chug happened?
The Viking chug.
And it wasn't even his puke. It was someone else's puke.
Oh, it was
that was
fucking
another
insane.
Pat Duffy, his trifecta.
He's an animal. Yeah. Pat Duffy's a savage.
Pat Duffy. Hey, let me ask you, Pat Duffy, just nod because we don't have a mic on you. Do you have a fetish for girls' puke or no? No, you know, okay, because some guys like that shit. It's called Roman showers. There are guys that get off on it and pay hookers to do it.
Yeah, let's bring Pat Duffy
Pat
in
Duffy
here.
No, let's talk to Pat Duffy out there.
Who would ever thought that the Sergeant Magoo Fruit Loop trick was nothing?
Well, you stand over there.
Turns out to be nothing.
No, you don't. No, you stay over there is where people stay.
It was an appetizer.
You fucking look like you're
you
ready to raise a barn.
That you brought that up, the Roman showers. That means somebody's going to watch that thing tonight and jerk off to it.
You have no idea.
It's already happened.
Yeah.
If it's on my website, someone already's got the cock out right now.
Yeah.
Oh, you're just fucking puking in his mouth.
You fucking
fucking puking in his fucking mouth, you fucking whore.
I've seen all that shit, but he finally made a fucking cape of what I've been fantasizing.
And if someone hasn't, just because we talked about it, someone's got their dick out right now. Fuck yeah! Why didn't I think of that?
Those are the clothes you were wearing.
Yeah.
So,
well,
how did you...
I had to change my shirt.
Oh, how did you clean?
Ope told me to take this one off, so I have my undershirt on. And
how about
then,
the shorts?
Well, the shorts are the same. I still got puke all over them.
Smell
it's
nice.
In my Magoo poured water down my back, and now it's like all wet nuts.
And down your butt crack,
honestly,
you got
he doesn't
puke.
Look, he doesn't look bad considering what he went through.
Well, they handed me like a pile of paper towels.
And then I saw him pouring water over your head, giving you a little shower over the puke bucket.
What were you thinking as it's hitting your mouth?
Yeah.
I felt like my ex on a Saturday night.
What do you mean?
I always wanted to say that, sorry.
That's all right.
Hey, first one. First of many, my friend.
So, dude, this is when we tear the legend down.
Right. No, we gotta knock him off his pedestal a little
please
bit.
Don't. Literally, this will be my heroes crushing me. Please don't.
No, we love you, Pat Duffy.
No, what are you kidding after what you did?
So, Pat Duffy,
Audie Murphy.
As it's coming, what are you thinking?
I was just waiting for it, and I knew it was going to be disgusting, but I knew it was going to be mostly eggnog, so it wouldn't be that big of a deal.
How bad was the smell?
Disgusting. I didn't think the smell was going to be as bad as it is.
See, that? You know why? It wasn't only eggnog.
Exactly.
Where did you go, like, mentally? What did you tell yourself?
Just a happy place.
Vietnam.
Just a happy place. Yeah.
You saw choppers happy and fucking
place.
Agent Orange.
Yeah.
Napalm.
Take the pain.
Oh,
why did you decide to open your
think
eyes?
Think of an El Zarqawi beheading.
To see if I could see through it.
He did open his eyes.
Yeah.
In the middle of
that.
See through it.
It's in my ears still. Everything's kind of muffled still.
Oh my God. He's got puke in his ears.
How are you going to get that out? You put a Q-tip. You're going to push it in further.
I blew my nose. It was all eggnog.
Wow. You really do stink, too.
I know.
I can smell it now.
Don't make him feel bad. He's a good boy.
Hey, you guys,
we love Pat Duffy.
Can we rehear it?
Danny's pulling it right now.
Yeah, I gotta hear
we're
that.
We're throwing on CD or something? Yeah. Make it easy that way? All right. We're going to replay it in a second here.
I'm again trying to
I think we got your
load
dad on
Rogan's
really?
Page.
It's that's awesome.
Pat's dad?
We got to get him headphones.
I can't hear you.
We got to get him guest headphones that we never use.
Yeah, get him the headphones.
He has puke in his ear.
Oh, God, that what? Smell is back. Oh. Why do we... We need some sort of isolation booth for these moments.
Hang on, Kate.
Oh, jeez, yeah, that's my dad.
It is your dad?
Yeah,
I'm on the phone.
Hey, Pat's dad.
Opie, what's happening, bro?
What's up? What's your name?
Mike.
Hey, Mike, how are you? What do you think of your son today?
$35,000 of education money. This is it. You better give him a job.
Hey, you know how hard it is to get an internship on our show, and he just got it.
Thank you.
Apparently,
yeah, I know.
Heard.
I turned him on to your show way back when, the NEW days.
Back in 99.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah. I emailed you a bunch of months ago and told you all about it.
Your son is a champion.
Yeah, he's a champion, and he's got an internship because of what he did today.
Rare stock.
Actually, someone we hired to be an intern is now fired.
Sucks
to be you. We got to make a spot for Pat Duffy.
That's me.
It's like when Michael Jordan came into the league and just showed everybody the next level.
Right.
Yep.
Yeah, it's like... He's like, there's no one. No one's going to come close to that. You'd have to shit in his mouth. You'd have to force diarrhea. That's next year. You're going to have to force diarrhea. Someone's going to have to take massive fucking laxatives, squeeze their asshole shut, and someone's going to have to lean their head over a toilet bowl and shit in someone's mouth. That's the only way we're going to beat this. Just explode shit all over someone's mouth. That's the only way it could be beaten.
I've gotten to Rogan's site. I am watching some of the video from his phone.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, this is just...
Baby bird.
You got him in, like, mid-puke there to start. But, look, it just cascades out of his mouth all...
just all the over sheer volume.
Oh, look at that. There's no way a man can puke that much. And his face is covered. And it went on and on
and on. Dude, that's pretty gross.
Yeah, I thought it was over at one point, but it wasn't at all.
Yeah,
that's when you took the ear shot.
Yeah, that was the ear shot.
Anthony, Sam is working on our crystal clear video.
Little competition. That's amazing.
Our version will be crystal clear.
Oh, I saw your version is phenomenal because he turns his head to the side like to try to spit out, and then Pat throws up in his ear, like right in his ear.
I gotta see it.
Hey, Pat's dad, anything else?
Nah, just tell him I said McGillicuddy, nice job. I'll catch you later. I got to make a delivery.
I'll see you at pizza night, Duff.
All right, any plugs out there?
Bud.
You want to plug anything there, Mike?
Nah, I'm driving an Exxon truck. How's that?
All right, you're all good? All right.
So you and your dad get along.
All right, thank you, Mike. Take care, buddy. You and your dad get along good, right?
Oh, yeah. He's really the reason that I'm into radio and everything.
They're like friends. Oh, yeah. And his dad are like fucking buddies.
He calls him Duff.
Yeah.
I really rip him apart, like, all the time. Pizza nights are ridiculous. We have pizza every Friday night. The whole time I just rip my dad apart.
Yeah.
That's good.
It's good like you.
Yeah.
You know.
Wow. That's sweet.
All right, we're just waiting for the audio. Danny's going to bring it in any second, so I got to hear that again.
Really I'm actually hungry.
Smelling in here.
Yeah, I got some food coming, man.
Yeah, me too.
George in Jersey, what's up?
Dude, that had to have been the best fucking radio I've ever heard in my life.
Oh.
Crazy. Hey, listen, is Rogan still over there? I was wondering if he could send me that pic on his phone, man.
Yeah, Rogan will just send you something. What are you
doing? If you go to joerogan.net, it's up on the front page if you can get it to load.
Yeah.
I don't have a computer, man. That's why.
Oh, well, you're fucked. Computer.
Give your number off the air, and Rogan will give you his number, and you guys can send videos back and forth. But
just
do it off the air, because that's the way Joe operates.
All right. Hold on. Yeah,
no computer.
Send me a
Nickelodeon of it.
Maybe you can come over and teach you karate, too, in a room. You both dress like Roman
and Elvis in the studio stinks.
Yeah, Carl in Jersey, what's up?
Hey, what's happening? I had to, unfortunately, tune out of your walkover because I wanted to hear those assholes start their show. And they said they needed a fan because it stunk like lemon pledge and throw up. And they must have, like, an intern or some producer or some shit in the background. And he was just throwing up all over the place. They just couldn't take it. They were puking. Really, really pissed
The puking
off.
Is continuing over at the other studio.
Puking is so contagious.
Yo, I'm not even joking, man. It's like you can hear the guy in the background throwing up.
They got a couple couple of they had a couple of chicks that worked for him too, I think, and that's the worst because girls don't react well to vomit.
No,
I wonder what the real numbers of people throwing up listening were.
It had
crazy. Hey,
yeah,
Logan.
Like 100,000 people.
Yeah. Joe,
what's up, dude?
I love you, Joe. You're the man.
Thank you, man.
You know, oh, and I had a man too, but you know, just kind of throw some props out.
Joe came up with the idea.
Yeah,
Joe. Oh, nobody, crazy. No one in their right mind would have thought that was possible. So why bring it up?
Gotta tell
and
you,
Joe Rogan.
Yep.
Hey, puke in his mouth. Okay. Did he just say okay? Why?
I know. I thought Joe was just being ridiculous.
Yeah.
Just going, hey, wouldn't this be wacky?
And Ant and I are great at talking people into doing stuff. So I'm thinking, all right, great idea. This might take an hour, but I think we can get it done. It was like immediate.
I had faith in that kid.
Immediate.
Thank you.
There is
I had faith in that Pat Duffy. There's something about that kid. The look in his eyes. I'm like, this kid can do it.
He's unflappable.
There is a still
picture. He's a champion.
Yeah.
On a thread on Whackbag that says, congratulations, Pat from Unaki. It says, congratulations to Pat from Unaki on his first place win. We knew you could do it. And then there is a still photo of... I cannot even describe the amount of puke.
People are going to say that's fake. They're going to say that's fake.
It looks like it was done at Lucasfilm.
Wow.
It can't be real.
Get that.
Oh my God.
I'm really proud of myself.
That is.
Oh my God.
Get that on too.
You are being drowned by vomit right there.
I'm very proud of myself at the moment.
Jesus.
Brian, if you're listening, get that up on my front page too.
No, get that.
That doesn't look real.
Because someone really captured it.
I have to assure the people it is absolutely authentic.
That's a perfect shot.
It is a perfect shot. The sheer vomit. You can't see his head. His entire head is obscured by a cavalcade of vomit.
That picture's on Whackbag. We're going to get it on opieandanthony.com.
There's only one way to describe it. The baby bird.
The baby bird.
Get that on Opie and Anthony?
Get away from
me. That description, that name will live in infamy. The baby bird.
Get the fuck away. Are you insane?
Dude, we could sell that shot. That is a beautiful shot. Man, that says it all right there.
Oh, my God.
Hang it up on your wall.
I would hang that up on my wall.
Yeah, that's a print.
Because he's in a power position, Pat from Monaki. He's almost like a gladiator.
You know what? For next year, you guys should put flyers up. Put this. You could put this in fucking Madison Square Garden. Put flyers up all around the city. This year, we will top it.
Right.
And have that poster.
Yeah.
We will top the baby
next
bird.
Next year, we finally bring this out to you guys. It's got to be at a venue next year.
It has to be.
And a big one, too.
Pat Duffy has to sit outside. Pat, we love you. No offense. You're terrific.
Did a great job.
You don't believe
but you got to get the fuck out of here.
Sure, whatever plug you want.
I just want to plug my MySpace page, myspace.com/allpurposecleaner.
All purpose cleaner.
Wow. You're going to remember
how
that,
appropriate.
Though. Yeah, no kidding.
Certainly.
You guys want to hear the finale?
Yeah.
Please.
You guys got it in a good spot?
Yeah.
Any setup needed? Nothing?
No, it starts right as Pat is about to lose it.
All
right,
so it's the baby bird. We had Pat Duffy, his head over the garbage pail, like he's getting his hair washed before a haircut.
Yep.
And Pat is about to get rid of 75 double shots of eggnog. Here we go.
He's just drinking now. He's up to 76.
Uh-oh. Here we go.
Here it goes.
Oh, my God.
The baby bird is going down.
The baby bird is happening. It's happening.
The baby bird is happening. I almost wet myself. I swear to you. I'm laughing so hard.
We
lost Jimmy. He's laughing so hard. He ran into the corner. Oh, yeah!
A thunderous round of applause.
Down goes Pat. Down goes Pat.
He's wearing puke blackface.
That was the greatest moment in radio history, period.
Yeah.
It's impossible to top that.
Yeah,
that's impossible.
And there you go. We're back. Oh, wow. Is that great to listen to?
Wow.
The shock and pandemonium that went on.
I like how Opie kept trying to talk, and right as he'd start to say half a sentence, Pat would puke again.
Oh.
He'd be like, he just...
I like how you kept saying, there's no way that's going down. There's no way that is going down.
That was, I think it was him.
Was that you?
Yeah.
It's hard to tell who is who.
And the first vomit, the first bit of vomit went into his mouth and wasn't like that fire hose vomit.
Right.
So we were like, oh my God, the baby bird's happening. And it just kept getting worse and worse and worse. Just so you could hear the crowd like escalating with each one. We were like, no. And then when he turned his head.
Are we getting that shot up on opiananthony.com? All right, here's the deal. Anthony, people are trying to see the video on Joe Rogan's site. JoeRogan.net,
yeah.
Your site's pretty much crashed. We just mentioned Whackbag. They're pretty much in screwed mode right now as well. People are like going all over the place trying to find the video and the pictures.
On YouTube.
It's going to be up on YouTube.
It's on YouTube already because it's on YouTube through my site.
All right. And it's also going to be on opiananthony.com very soon. Right there, Steve-O.
Indeed.
You all right?
I'm getting there.
Oh, God.
Holy
That audio,
crap.
was awesome. Perfect. It just encapsulated how fucking amazing
and,
that
and
that,
some
that,
dopes are like, all we're hearing is you guys reacting. If you can't figure out the pictures at that point, I don't know what to tell you.
If you when radio you see the might video not be for you. And you hear the audio together, fucking God.
It sounded like there were 150 people in there.
Yeah.
And there was like 12.
All disgusted.
We did 150-something episodes of Fear Factor. I've never seen anything even come close to that.
To being
it's like
that.
Watching people chew gum. It was like watching someone else chew somebody else's gum. That's what every stunt on Fear Factor was. he's chewing someone else's gum. This is crazy.
We just blew Joe Rogan's mind.
Nothing's going to do
it. It was his idea.
Mark in South Carolina, what's up?
Hey, man, that seemed like a true-life version of the Aristocrats.
Oh, Pat should have done that.
Oh, that would have been hilarious.
Where is Pat? We haven't seen him yet?
Pat from Anaki.
He's probably dropping soft serve into the toilet over at 3
soft
FM.
Well, it takes a lot out of him. Last year, he was pretty much passed out in the bathroom for like an hour. He was shitting and puking for like an hour, and then he started sleeping on the urinal. I mean, on the toilet there.
Yes.
My God. I don't want to hear from the people that almost turned the radio off. Whatever. Let's say hi to Brian in Canada. XM Canada checking in. Brian.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Hey.
Hi.
I just got to let you guys know that when you bring guests on your show, you bring absolutely the best out of your guests. And I owe Joe Rogan an apology because I wouldn't have given him an ounce of credit until listening to him yesterday and today. So I apologize, Joe, and keep up the good
work. If I didn't know me, I'd probably think I was a dick, too.
Joe's the man.
No, Joe's the man.
Joe, and we got the good stuff in Canada, man.
You think you got the good stuff. The good shit's in California. We got botanists and scientists. You guys got a
I know, that's awesome. I got the
players.
Exactly. What are you guys doing? Fucking raiding Paul Bernardo's backyard.
Joe, I got a story that you'll appreciate. You might not believe me, but one time I was taking 5 pounds with me, selling it from across the country, sat on a train next to this dynamite girl, was talking to her. There's no seats on the train. I said to her, what do you do for a living? She goes, I'm a cop. I said, you've got to be fucking kidding me. I swear to God in my life.
She was dynamite?
Half an hour later, she's jerking me off.
Really?
On the train.
You got jerked off by a cop? The only thing would be better if you came into the marijuana.
Yeah, and they made her smoke it.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow, you got jerked off by a cop?
Yeah, jerked off by a cop carrying 5 pounds a week.
Wow. That's a pretty fucking good story.
I got blown by a cop, but it was Kenny.
Kenny couldn't take it.
That's the one story I've got to tell for the rest of my life, but that's
a good story, dude.
All right, right on. Let's go to Alan in Texas. Alan.
Yeah, what's happening?
What's up, Alan?
That was the best radio I've heard yet. I'm buying like 5 XMs for 5 of my friends just on today alone.
All right,
good boy. That was awesome. I couldn't even hear my own radio over my own screaming.
Hey, that's pretty cool. That's a compliment. Bill, the trucker, what's up?
You know, on that video, if I tune it in, I do not want to see that stupid Foundry Music logo all over the money shot.
No, it'll be on YouTube, man. It's on YouTube clean from my website. And it'll be all over the place, man.
Yeah, tell freaking Steve to make his Foundry Music logo a little small, so it's all about the baby bird.
We need just pure puke.
Oh, is he putting the watermark on the video? Just throw the video up, man.
Just the video.
Everybody doesn't know FoundryMusic.com by now?
Yeah, they know.
Make sure it makes it a little smaller than usual, please.
Is it going to be OpieAnthony.com on there?
Yeah, it will.
What about eatabullet.com?
Well, actually, myspace.com/JimNorton has the HD video. The high definition version, but I don't want to plug it. But if you want to go there, and there's also a free download, and you can scratch and smell it. That's a
interaction,
up
stop motion, different camera angles,
and a lot of laughs.
Make your mouse vibrate when the throw up hits. It's got like a shock effect.
That cop story turned me on. That was very sexy.
That was kind of cool.
Yeah. Fuck yeah, she jerked us. I'm in a hand job role. It's all I'm thinking about is getting jerked off lately.
Why hand jobs?
I don't know. I can't stop buying them from fucking. I go to these clip fucking stores online, and all I want to do is get fucking innocent hand job videos.
Really?
You get videos of hand jobs?
Really?
They're a hand job?
Yeah, that seems like the beginning of
fetish,
the video.
But there's something sexy about that. About a guy getting jerked off. There's something innocent about getting jerked off. And if a girl jerks you off right, there's nothing. I mean, there's a lot better, but I mean, it's fucking hot.
Nothing better, man.
Thanks,
nothing
Ken.
Better than something you could do by yourself.
No, I like a girl to jerk me off. Because I guess there's just the motion of a smooth hand job.
Thank you, sir.
Most girls aren't that good. I used to do a joke about having a girl jerk you off. It's like trying to brush your teeth with your left hand. It's like, there's no way you can get the same rhythm, you know? Your right hand. My right hand knows every fucking cranny. My left hand is just palsy. I can't get a speed going. When a girl's jerking me off, I gotta hold my breath, see if I can come quicker. Like,
your toes are all pointed out and shit.
Yeah. Squeezing it.
Squeezing,
try.
And then the rhythm just gets messed up.
And then they get tired, they have to switch hands.
Yeah, they do this, they open, close their hand. It's like, look, you're not throwing a knuckleball, Negro. Grab my dick again.
God, I hope you hurry up. I don't know how long.
Hey, Jamie Massad is here from the Laugh Factory.
Buddy. He's here in studio?
He's right over there. We'll talk to him next.
No way. He wants to talk more about Kramer. How long is he going to milk that shit?
No kidding. The owner of the Laugh Factory.
He's going to ride that bitch right into the beach.
Oh, yeah, I love the
where
apology
the Kramer thing happened. There'll be no more N-word all over the world. We're going to have a special speech. And no more N-word.
And as he's doing that, the Laugh Factory logo is right behind him.
Yeah.
Huge.
We're going to march with Laugh Factory flag with a big N-word. It's going to say nigger, but with a line through it. So no more. So everybody know what we say.
All right, we're going to step aside. Bill Burr in studio. Joe Rogan in studio. Joe's playing Caroline's here in New York City all weekend long. And
Kenny, walking around rather quickly.
All good?
All hustle and bustle. Ooh,
thanks, a little pepper for my egg whites. Thanks, Kenny.
Mr. Rogan, would you like anything?
No, I'm good, brother. Thank you.
Mr. Thanks. Racist?
Thank you.
Amazing Racist is okay. All right.
Mr. Bird?
Ladies and gentlemen, Mama Bird. Mama Bird has entered the studio. It's the Opie and Anthony Show. At from Munaki. New in love. By the way, this is like the post show. Yeah, from the eggnog drinking contest. Yeah. Now we get all the interviews and
he
stuff.
He should have a towel around his neck.
Yeah.
In front of a locker.
The champion. Pat, I never doubted you, first of all. Never doubted you. I thought that love thing was going to be a little bit of a problem, but right when the competition started, you could see you again relaxed, not even a problem, doing the shots. Everybody else kind of had that look on their face. They were scared. You, a true champion, and congratulations on your victory this year.
Well, thank you. It was a little rough, but love pulled me through.
And he set the record, too, his own record, 75 double shots.
Oh, you should tell your girl that you had to look at her face to get what you're throwing up on someone's mouth.
Yeah.
You're thinking of her.
By the way,
for her.
The shot of the competition, I think one of the whack baggers captured this, but it's now on opianthony.com. This is the shot of the competition. This will be on so many freaking computer screens in the coming days.
That, to me,
is
the
perfect shot
that says it all.
Ali is over Frazier.
Yeah.
You know, that
Sonny Liston.
Sonny Liston. That's just a famous sports shot
there. I just love, like, the white light. It's like his soul.
It
doesn't
look real.
It's leaving his body.
Yes.
It's like an exorcist or something is going on there.
Could someone do us a favor and make that into a poster so we can have it in our studio?
Please. Like a spider covering his prey.
And then, Baby Bird. Just sitting there with his arms folded, completely relaxed, as if this is the natural
It's
way
so
to
funny
feed.
How Steve has to get that foundrymusic.com URL on it.
Perish the thought. His logo isn't on it.
It looks like what was in Marcellus Wallace's suitcase.
That is just amazing how much volume is coming out. And I like his stance, too. He's got a nice stance for the power boot.
He didn't even really bend over to aim that much at his mouth. Because why bother with that much coming out?
He kept good posture.
It's
yeah,
like
good
old,
posture.
Old football card picture. That last eggnog was wafer thin.
And it's hard to describe how covered. He's obscured from the waist to his head. All you see are his legs. You puked all over his upper half.
Looks like I'm building a human.
Pat Duffy is insane.
That is an
That the picture is just amazing.
It's just it's so beautiful how the whole event just escalated.
Escalated. Couldn't have asked for
perfect
a better
ending. Timing wise, perfect
contest.
It really was the greatest moment.
It was
the greatest moment in radio history.
You look like a dragon, Pat. You look like like you're a mythical creature.
It's Godzilla.
Boot the magic dragon.
Pat's on fire today.
You feeling all right
like
now?
Like a monk.
You
feeling all right?
Oh yeah, I puked out most of it, and then I
shit
out most of it.
Cool.
Yeah.
Did you check your?
It was getting very liquidy.
You
say I love
shit
you.
In his mouth. Yeah. He probably would have done that.
I had to throw away my underwear over in.
Oh God! Why?
Someone should get that and put it on eBay. You get $1,000 for that underwear
with the hole in the middle.
Or say
you put
the
on the seat.
Yeah.
And I think something happened where there was a little splatter going on, so I had to.
What? You got some shit in your underwear?
Yeah, a little splatter effect.
Oh, that's what happens. That's healthy.
Now where is
sell that underwear?
Where's the underwear? Just in
3FM.
No, I know that. Just where though? Just throw it in the.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. In the garbage in the bathroom.
So you going commando?
Yeah.
Under the sound booth, like so the fucking next fucking phone screen.
Yeah. What is that? No.
Wow. So you're running without any underwear. You got some splatters and you puked on a man's face.
Yeah.
All right. See the shot on opinionanthony.com.
All for a woman.
It's just amazing.
All for the love of a woman.
Yeah.
Our website's getting destroyed too. By the way, all websites are getting destroyed as people try to find pictures and video and. And whatnot from the contest. We're going to have hundreds of pictures up eventually. And Sam ran home to get the video up on YouTube.
The real video. He's got some crystal clear.
Oh, yeah.
Joe Rogan got the first video out there.
Yes,
but,
he did.
You know, we'll have even better videos as we
cell
go.
Cell phone. The new LG Envy.
And what the hell is HDNet going to do with that video, I wonder?
Hey, did now does Master Paul realize he's going to have to step up his game to compete as they're trying to suit the young lady, the same young lady? They're courting her.
They're courting.
Two suitors.
For real?
Yeah, and now Master Poe's going to have to realize that...
No, I'm not even courting her.
He's in the back seat.
Oh. Master Poe's trying to bang your girl?
No. No?
Does she know you like her?
I think so. I told her
Told her he
times.
Was in love with her.
He said, I love you to her.
You tell her a lot?
And she was like, I love
Does
you.
She pretended
like I danced on the big piano.
You didn't really, did you?
Yeah.
I thought you were joking.
No.
You went to FAO Schwartz and danced on the piano like big...
Yeah.
Dude, she just wants, you know.
From the new movie, Fat.
She doesn't want all that romancing. She wants to get right into it.
Have you stuck it in yet?
You want to bring her in? Joe, you want to get the feel for what's going on here?
Sure.
Pat is in love with this girl that you're about to meet for
the
first time.
In, for sure.
She's a nice
really
girl.
Head over heels.
Yeah, I mean, you got to respect him as a champion now, you know?
Yeah. When's the last time somebody won a championship and they didn't get pussy that night?
Absolutely.
He's at the peak of his powers right now.
This is the girl that Pat's in love with. We're not really sure if she's in love with Pat, though.
We don't know. They're friends.
And she's living with Master Poe, by the way.
Living
she
in the same
in my
house?
Chair.
Yeah. Yeah.
Look at Pat. What a gentleman.
Really when nice. He sleeps upstairs, she sleeps on the couch downstairs and vice versa. Never
gentleman.
The twain
dogs
shall meet in bed.
Dogs too. I can't
with
hear
the dogs.
Mic. Turn her mic
Does
up, please.
Does Pat shave with a shard of glass every morning?
An ice pick.
A shard of Are you proud of your man?
Her friend.
Oh, could you just fake it and say, are you proud of your man?
Yes, I'm proud of my man.
Your man. See, I'm helping you out there, Pat.
Oh, thank you.
I'm trying to fucking help
Pat, why don't you tell her that you love her again, and then let's see what she has to say. And then Joe's taking a look here. He'll give you an honest opinion here.
Tanya?
And this is real, by the way, Joe. This isn't a dumb radio bit. The Pat really loves this girl.
I love you. With all my heart.
I love you, too.
Didn't sound quite the way I said it.
No, it's kind of like, I love you like, you know, a friend.
So depressing. In the height of his powers.
I know. This is
as
like...
as it's going to get.
Are you feeling anything, Joe?
Right all now. Downhill from here.
No. There's no energy there
this
at all.
This is the best
I guess he wasn't impressed by my puking.
Did well, no, maybe it was I had to throw my underwear out because I shit in them. Story.
This is the best you're... Oh,
there's nothing happening there. That's like trying to start a fire rubbing two wet newspapers together. There's nothing going on.
Nothing going on, right?
Pat, you do understand. Like, this is the best your feathers are going to look, your plumage. This is the best,
you're
you know, you look. Yeah, you can never look better than this. And she's kind of...
Laughing at me?
Yeah.
Well, have you guys ever made out or anything?
No.
Making out? How are you in love with her?
Because it makes me happy to make her happy.
Whoa. Thanks. All right, listen.
What a weird biological trick that is, huh?
Wow. Let's get into this, though. You moved from Missouri, right?
Right.
And you're living with Master Paul?
Right.
Have you made out with Master Paul?
No.
Come on.
You know,
Missouri. Oh, you rolled your eyes. You have made
Missouri
out with Master
Poe. Show me.
You're lying.
Have you woken up unconscious?
Have you ever blown Master Poe?
No.
No kissing?
No.
Jerked
hey.
Him off?
Hey.
Nothing?
Hey.
You're checking, bro. You didn't know.
Oh, hey, look at Pat stepping
Pat's
in.
Pat's getting a little defensive.
Nothing?
A little defensive.
Pat and Rogan are going to throw down.
Should we get Master Poe in here?
So you and Master Poe just buddies?
Master Poe!
Yes, Master Poe is my buddy.
Have you ever woken up unconscious feeling as though you've been touched? Like maybe you would.
Watch out if he takes his shoes off. All right, Billy Jack.
Billy Jack.
Master Poe is staring down Pat Fromenaki now. Why?
We need a little mic. Yeah. Why is that? I really want to know the dynamic.
Yeah.
Here.
There's something going on. Pat really, really loves this girl. This is not a radio bit.
And he's claiming his woman. Look at his hand.
Yeah. We're getting
his
We're getting Master Poe a mic now.
Yep. Pat right now has his hand on her shoulder. She's got a little light-up Christmas hat on, and now he's rubbing her shoulder a little bit.
Ooh.
You bought her that hat?
Yes, I
yes, did.
Oh, okay. And you're wearing it with pride.
It was by the tree lighting. I took her to see the tree.
You two went to the tree lighting?
Yeah. No, not the lighting. It was too crowded for that.
See the tree.
Yeah.
I never seen a Christmas. Sorry, never had a Christmas tree before, so.
Never did? What?
Yeah.
What the they went got going
me.
On?
They went and got me a Christmas
what,
tree.
What are you, Jew?
No.
No.
He's what never had a
down
Christmas
there in Missouri.
Yeah.
And this is going to be the bestest Christmas for her ever. Yeah. I'm going to make sure.
It's going to be a trailer park Christmas.
Let's get Master Poe involved here.
Master Poe.
Good morning, gentlemen.
This is a roommate of yours?
Yes.
Don't talk so. You got to back off the mic.
Poe's very animated this morning. He's very clipped.
Yeah, what's going on, Paul?
Now,
Paul?
She lives in your house.
Yes, she does.
Now, how did this come about?
Well, she had a very bad situation in Missouri, and she came over here to New Jersey. And Pat, myself, and Jay are helping her out.
All right. Bad situation, bad relationship?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you had to get out of there? Restraining orders?
No, I just left.
You just left? Was he abusive?
Yeah.
Yeah. Was it a boyfriend?
God.
Yes. Oh, I was going to. Next question was a really hurtful one. Family member. But, okay, boyfriend, kind of abusive.
Did he beat you with a
mentally or physically?
Yes.
Yes. Both.
Both, yeah.
Oh, boy. Pat's very. Pat has a big rescuing instinct in this one, I think.
Is.
Maybe all you needed
was Mama Bird.
Q-tips to clear your ears out so you could hear better.
That's why she's staying at Poe's, because Poe's very protective.
Ah.
Not only. A F.H. Riley guy.
Yeah.
He's also very protective.
He's a master
in the... Did you say F.H. Riley's?
Yeah, 400 New York Ave, Huntington, New York. Yes, right.
Yeah, I know that place.
Very fine.
Poe is protective. If he sees a green shirt that matches nothing, he fucking guards it with his life. I'm sorry, Poe.
Guards those free turkeys, too.
A fucking black suit with a dark green shirt.
All right, Poe. So now you went online, I guess, and described your situation as being dire.
No.
What happened? How did they find out that you were in trouble?
I was on Pal Talk, and just I told one person, and they I finally, for like months I didn't, but they knew something was up, so.
Yeah.
And then they just got me out of the place, and I moved down here. And
so you came down here from Missouri just because of the internet, because of Pal Talk?
No, just I wanted to get out of the situation.
Yeah, but I mean, but the connection was made through the internet? That's pretty badass.
Just through the internet.
That's fucking
Pal
crazy, man.
Really not everybody gets abducted. Some people get rescued.
My website, on my message board, people have gotten married, had kids, all kinds of crazy relationships. People have died. Very bizarre, man.
Yeah,
the internet's crazy. It's a total different world, man.
Yeah. So Poe decided he'd be the place that you would live?
Yeah.
You had a choice now, I guess. You could have stayed with Pat.
Him or a couple other people.
In the trailer. Or you could have stayed with Poe.
Right. No, I met her after.
Well, yeah. I was went to Poe's and
then
I met him.
Oh, so you had already been living with Poe.
Yes.
Now, was there any... Did you detect... maybe at the beginning, maybe things were kind of nipped in the bud. Did you detect Poe perhaps wanting a little more than just a roomie?
No.
Never?
No.
Always a gentleman.
Very.
But you guys made it at one point.
Poe.
Any comment on why you didn't maybe try? I know, you know, you fashioned yourself the Casanova. I just want to know why maybe you didn't make any moves.
She's gone through enough emotional damage.
That she didn't need the likes of you.
That's right.
Trying to.
Did you ever sing to her?
Yes.
I did?
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay.
What did you sing to her?
From one form of abuse to another.
George Michael.
All right, Pat. Touche.
I'm pretty sure they've made out.
Buddy.
What?
Think
I'm
so?
Pretty sure. Yeah.
Why? All right.
Why do you say that?
I've seen lying before. They've made out.
Sure. Being a Jew, everyone you know does it.
Touche. Do you drink?
Yes.
To excess?
No.
I never remember. You drink a little bit.
Yes.
A little pot?
No, not no more.
No, not no more.
I used to.
All right.
Poe, okay. Did you make out with her?
Trying to get a little background.
He won't tell. He's a gentleman, but she's already told me all she needs to.
Those eyes, smile.
How come you believe it when I say I didn't make out with her?
You got a point there, Pat. So now, all right, they're living together. They're roomies, whatever it is, helping each other out. There's another party involved or a couple other people that were going to help you.
A friend of his, Jay.
A friend of his, Jay.
Yes.
All right, what's going on with Jay?
They're just helping me get my life together, basically.
Get your life together by maybe helping you, find a job? You got a job.
Can I jump in for a second? Yeah. There's a lot of helping going on. Why don't we ever help the fat chicks?
They can help themselves.
Exactly.
They're coming out of the woodwork.
We help them. If there's a fucking door, we help them get to it and push them through it. Beat it, pig.
Getting a lot of help.
You certainly are getting a lot of help from a lot of people from across the country. All right, they're helping you out. Now, Pat comes into the picture.
Right.
So he met you at Poe's house.
Yes.
Now, what brought you to Poe's house?
I'm friends with Poe. I live not too far from him, and I come over every once in a while.
All right, you go over every once in a while.
He goes over there for heat. Yeah.
Yeah.
And shelter.
When you want to shit, not look at the grass underneath.
Hey.
You leave your trailer.
Start resembling that statement.
You leave your trailer, you go to Poe's house, and I guess you were invited over for Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
And you two start chatting.
Yep.
And you hit it off in some way, shape, or form.
Yeah. Like she laughs at my jokes.
Best.
Where am I going to find a girl like that?
Like my best
anybody like that.
Friend. When a girl says he's like my best friend, you're so out.
Are you afraid that, fooling around with Pat would hurt the friendship?
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, I hope to ruin the friendship sometime in the future. Yes.
It makes it better.
Pat wants to just destroy the friendship with some ass sex.
Well, yes. I look in the mirror, and I go, I'm not attracted to me, so why should anybody else be attracted? I'm going to lose a whole shitload of weight, and I haven't been working because I don't really care. Now I have something I care about.
And I'm his navigator.
Yeah, she's my navigator when she's not working.
He wants to play Baby Bird with you while he's still able to whistle.
Ow.
Pat's at my house till about 1, 2 o'clock in the morning sometimes.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
So wait a minute.
Yes.
Now, you're kind of saying you have something that motivates you, and it's Tanya.
Yes.
What do you guys sing in the car, for anybody that might not have heard earlier?
All kinds of... Once Bitten, Twice Shy. That's one of her favorite songs.
Oh, you like that one?
Harley Davidson Road Song CD.
Yeah.
That's all scratched up now.
How old are you?
25.
Yeah.
25, but you're into a lot of this classic rock.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and Pat likes that. It kind of brings you two together a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How many times has she seen Pat cry?
Yeah. Have you seen him cry?
A little bit. A little, yeah. A little
bit. Movies?
Ew.
No.
Yeah, Legends of the Fall, really.
Well, no, wait, not movie. Yeah. Wait.
He opens
Pat's
up.
He's a sensitive guy.
He opens up to you a little bit about
what happened, Tanya?
I was telling him a story once, and
I was telling her about how I wasn't happy, and then I met her, and now I'm happy.
And he came
That's
terrific.
Let me tell you something, Pat.
That's terrific.
You should actually be in a book about love and everything you should not do.
Yeah.
Especially at the beginning.
Oh.
You are doing everything wrong. And I'll tell you why he's at your house till 2:30 in the morning.
He's making sure she's fucking asleep.
Yeah, he doesn't
out of the fight
whatsoever.
Yeah. It's right. Like he'll just be there watching and go, okay, yeah, I'll
he's
leave.
Poe blocking.
Poe, you got to be up at 3:30 in the morning. Yeah. Time
you know
to get
how
to
that
bed.
Is.
I tell him to stay till 2 o'clock in the morning.
And then he goes back to the trailer and just stares at the stars through the hole in the roof.
my sunroof.
Look at that, a shooting star. Let me wish upon it. Cessna crashing into your house, but... lives right by Teterboro.
Toto Barrow.
It's always a toe joke.
It really is.
Yeah. Have you seen his nine toes?
I guess.
Yeah.
How'd you lose a toe?
Diabetes.
Eggnog. Yeah. A little sugar. I didn't take care of my sugar. Got a little high. 465, I believe, when I walked in the emergency room. Hacked it off. $250,000 bill later.
For 250 grand for taking a toe off?
Well, I had like a 2.5 months of antibiotic treatment.
Sounds like the fucking mob.
Yeah.
We would have done it for 100 grand.
Oh, yeah. Take your fucking toe. And
so how often do you have to take insulin?
I take something else called Byetta. Works pretty good.
How often do you have to take it?
That's my sister's name.
Every day.
Hey, how much?
Once a day? Just once a day?
Yeah, it's like an injectable thing.
Oh, you take a shot every day.
Hey, all right, Paul, nice. do you see, you know, Pat making the moves on her?
No, he's a gentleman.
Yes.
He wants
her.
He could be a gentleman, but
you know
he's in love.
You know, we're both getting our shit together, so we have time.
It's kind of a mutual like misery thing that you're both going through. So you see this as a way to bond in misery.
Yes. She has a look on her face like there's not enough time in the universe.
Wait a minute now, Kanye, is that what it is for you? I mean, we don't know. Is it a matter of just like is Pat getting stuff? Like, Pat has some goals now that you've motivated him to want to achieve. Like he wants to lose weight. Throw up on other men's mouths and shit his pants in the bathroom.
Yeah.
I plan on being a different person in 3-6 months.
Really?
3-6?
So, whatever she thinks, 30, now, it doesn't matter. We are friends. We do get along and we listen to the same music. We have fun. She laughs. Blah, blah, blah,
so, you're changing for her?
Aren't you essential?
You're trying to be
changing.
What she wants.
No, this is what I've wanted, but I don't have the proper motivation.
Right.
Brundle Munaki.
Brundle Munaki. If nothing ever happens of it.
What a weird fly reference.
Puking on his food.
Yeah. And this is why they hang out with each other so much, because they like the same music.
Yeah.
So, the heart this guy is heading for.
We see it coming.
This is like the mistake like a 16-year-old makes.
Right.
This is like
everyone sees the heartbreak coming. It's on its way. You can hear the horn. Ooh, choo choo. It's coming. It's not even far away.
Well, let's ask what, Pat, how's this going to end in your world?
Yeah,
Pat?
How does it end in
murder,
your
suicide?
World?
No, odds are just misery.
Yeah, of
go
course.
Back in the trailer say this
by the
is
way,
where
so
I belong.
How do you want it to end? How do you want this to turn out?
You would like her as a girlfriend, right?
Marriage.
As a wife.
Yeah.
A wife. Our children. Little Pat from Munaki or wherever I'm living.
Oh, wow. And now, Tanya, what are you looking for? Like, of course, you've been through some shit. You come up here. You're trying to get your life together. What are your goals? Short term, medium term? Like, where do you want to be in, let's say, a year? What do you want to be doing with yourself?
You still want to be hooking up with Poe every couple weeks?
Hook up with Poe. I sleep with the dogs.
Yeah. The best option.
But do you want your own place?
Yes.
All right.
Eventually.
And a job. You say you got a job. What are you doing?
I'm working at Chevy's and his navigator.
Hey,
the Chevys I don't like because I can't understand the way they talk. They're all
Spanish.
Foreign and
bunch of PR
Hispanic. Yeah.
And I'm like, what?
What?
Chevy's like the Mexican food?
Yeah.
So all right.
All
to make a good fajita at Chevy's.
I like Chevy's.
Quesadillas, too.
Hey, Poe, how bad do you want her if she gets her act together?
Quesadillas? What's a quesadilla?
That's not even in
it's
my mind right now.
It's a cassette and quesadilla.
That hasn't crossed my mind at all.
What hasn't, Poe? No. I didn't hear you, sweetie.
I asked Poe how bad does he want her if she gets her act together.
Well, I mean, she's a very attractive girl. I mean, this is an honest question. It's not a bad question. Have you ever, like, been masturbating about something else and she flashes through your head because you happen to see her walk by in the night? It happens. That's not a bad question. If you're a guy, she's a beautiful girl. It doesn't mean you don't respect her.
My pop
it starts and ends with her.
No.
Now, no.
She is gorgeous. Absolutely. She's a very pretty.
What does she wear around the house?
Yeah, speaking of that, what does she wear?
Sweats.
But now, you should have a dress code in your house.
Two words.
Easy access. What kind of privacy is there as far as, you know, getting dressed, walking around the house? Maybe, you know, you got to go to the bathroom later at night. You walk out. You don't want to get dressed. What do you do?
Wrap a towel around me and run upstairs.
Little towel and run upstairs. And what do you, Paul, do you hear the creaking?
Have you seen her
do you hear
that?
The creaking
no,
up the stairs
there.
And open the door?
That'd be a nice visual that could seep into.
That's when he's not there. When he's there, I dress in the bathroom.
It doesn't mean that he's doing it thinking of you. It happens sometimes, like you're just doing it. You're in the middle of whatever fantasy you have. Maybe you're kicking teeth in somewhere and it's just another person.
Right.
It happens. Somebody walks through your fantasy.
Yeah, just because Norton's saying it doesn't mean it's gross.
It's a guest star.
Oh, boy. Yeah, I've had friends walk through my fantasy. It's not sexual. Actually, I'm jerking off. All of a sudden, I'm thinking of my buddy Bill D'Angelo. Like, what the hell Bill's doing? And then I'm like, oh, I'm back to reality.
Oh, back to jerking. Could you just stand up and, like, open your coat? I don't really get a good sense of you.
Yeah, she's a very cute girl.
Like, I want to see. I don't, because she's all covered up. Just
that's
see,
the idea.
She's not wearing
wow.
It. That's the idea. I just want to see. All right.
Very nice. Yeah. Lovely little figure.
Take a little spin.
A little Santa hat.
Like lift
little
there truck you go. All right.
Please.
You got a boob.
Yeah, that's, you know, that's nice.
Quite a hiney on her.
That's nice. I think you might be out of your
Pat
league.
Looks nervous.
For the first, you know.
Don't be nervous.
Well, respect, gentlemen.
With all due respect, Pat.
Yeah.
We're just saying, because she was, you know, wrapped up in a leather coat. We couldn't really see.
Oh, what a roller coaster ride today is for Pat. At the top of the heap and now just crashing into reality.
Yeah.
Just realizing the reality of the situation.
You're competing, you know, in some way or another, you know, even though it's just her living there. But there's some type of almost competition going on between Paul and Pat. Yeah?
Well, all right. Well, first of all, we don't get along. We're always arguing. Yeah. Okay?
You and Pat?
Always arguing.
That's called sexual tension.
Yeah, always arguing.
Why are you guys arguing? What's
I argue
the problem?
So much that I just walk out.
You right, and Tanya?
Yes.
Why? She says no. You're like, it's my house. I'll throw you out.
Why do you guys argue?
We argue because she wants to
stubborn.
Do things. Yeah, very.
You know who else?
Like about
and
what
my
thing?
Dogs, and my dogs, they love her. They protect her.
Yeah.
They growl at me now.
Is it true you renamed your house F.H. Poe?
Bruce Willis and Sybil Shepherd argued a lot on a little TV show called Moonlight.
That's exactly.
Right.
And they never...
Ted Danson, Shelley Long.
Right. They were always arguing.
Absolutely. Rieger and Danny DeVito.
Right.
What
they were
arguing
right
about?
Up until he fucked him in the ass.
Yeah. Well, like what? What? Give me an example.
Oh, yeah.
Like the other night, he didn't want me to come up here.
Why?
I don't know.
Paul.
You can't get in the way of our radio show, Paul
had that little blink. Paul blinked a couple times now.
Poe's mic blocking us.
All right, the last ONA show that she was at, she got carried away. And she drank and, you know, she did things that she wasn't supposed to.
What ONA show?
What did she do?
It was a Halloween show.
What things?
I got too drunk and my eyes were rolling in the back of my head.
What did you do that you're not supposed to?
And she disappeared.
But I haven't done that since, have I?
No, of course
not. What'd you do? You weren't supposed to. You fucked a black guy, didn't you?
No.
Are you
going to
tolerate that, Pat?
Oh. Poe's
almost arm's length away from him.
Legit question. What'd you do?
That's not
a bad question because you're saying you did something. You're like, yeah, but I didn't do it again. It's like, what'd you do?
I just got drunk and they were supposed to be watching me because, you know, I was nervous. And I wound up getting lost. I went took off with Patty and they got upset with me.
Stalker Patty?
No. Patty 2006.
She disappeared for 2 hours.
What, that's the new model?
So but wait, I was just up at
do
the...
Do you have a cell phone?
I do.
And you are a grown adult, right?
Right.
Can't you just go wherever you want to go?
Got drunk.
Oh, she just looked at Pope. You know something? Let me tell you something.
Paul has set down the rules. She's repeating this abusive relationship.
Right. I was just going to say something like
right.
that.
You're right.
You're absolutely right.
Yeah.
Maybe you're the way you are, you're looking for people. And you don't know this. A lot of women just do this subconsciously. You're looking at another kind of relationship where you're being dominated a little. And you. No offense, Paul. I'm just saying. Because you're not in a relationship, so that's kind of silly. But, you know, and here you have the sweetest guy in the world who would treat you like a princess.
The princess she is.
But you seem to want guys that are geared, where the fuck were you? You're not supposed to do this. You know, arguing all the time. And meanwhile, you'd say something to Pat, and he'd be, oh, okay, sweetie.
All yeah, right, you know what?
Let me just say, you guys are very perceptive.
Nothing dries her up more.
Yeah, Pat, yeah. You got to get a little right. Tough in your talk.
She wants, hey, bitch, what the fuck are you doing yeah. out?
And Poe's not yeah. abusive. Poe's not, I don't think he's abusive. I think Poe is just a rescuer, a codependent rescuer. He's not out there to dominate a chick or be mean to her. He just wants to smother her and love her. I don't think he's mean.
But his style is, hey.
And he's a Latin.
Where the fuck were you?
The Latins.
Where did you go?
Woman,
I told
me dinner.
You. Yeah, I told you this. You'll get something like that.
They're very parental.
Yeah.
That's right, but the Latins are very possessive. No, darker cocks hours. Than the whites.
Where okay. did you Where did you disappear off to?
Thanks, just Dan. Where that clock guy, whatever his name was.
Flavor Flav.
Uh-oh, wait, you were in Flav's dressing
with
room?
Six of his posse?
Oh, no. Fuck.
I just went to the front of the stage, was dancing and with Patty and Neo God.
And who?
Oh, Neo God. Is God.
Neo oh, wait is God. A minute. Were there girls involved? Because I looked down at one point.
Yeah, you were making out with some girl.
Happy tiny girl.
I swear to God, making out with a girl. Yeah, I think I saw that from the stage.
Frenchie no. there?
That was really me.
It was what's her name? The sexy one, baby girl from Pal
yeah,
Talk.
I saw a few
I don't know
if
it was you, but I saw baby girl kissing somebody.
I saw a few other girls
making
out.
She was probably kissing Frenchie. It wasn't me.
There was another girl involved with you.
Happy tiny girl?
Poe comment?
She was licking girls.
Did you see anything like that or hear about it?
Well, that was the time that she was gone for 2 hours.
Okay? Yeah.
All right, so we really didn't know where she was.
Well, you know
and
what?
Yes, she is 25, and she is a woman, so she yeah. can decide on where she wants to go.
But as long as she lives under your fucking roof,
it's going to be some rules. Rules.
No. Guys, okay, she was
topless unless you're eating
first
dinner.
First time I've seen Poe sweat.
Hey, Poe, have you said to her, look, I paid the bills around here. Has that come out yet?
That's right. Go in there and cook dinner. No.
So he's like, woman, get in there and clean the kitchen. Get in there and cook my dinner.
Why don't we wrap this up? Pat, why don't you get on your knee and confess your love to this professor.
It's been a while.
Is she uncomfortable with this, Tanya? Are you uncomfortable with this?
Pat, really, like, tell her why you love her and what you would like this, between the two of you. Just let her know exactly how you feel. That might be what she needs.
Anya.
Is that a fart? Or
pardon my breath.
pardon my breath.
Yes, I just puked on a man.
That could have been me. Have I told you lately I love you?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, a couple seconds ago. I would like to make a life with you in the future when I am a better person.
Are you going to cry?
Yeah, no.
Pat.
I'm going to squirt out my ass.
Pat, let's talk something.
My knee hurts real bad
what
right now. I'm
you?
So fat.
Tell yeah. Tanya what she means to you, how she's changed your life. Because
I mean, you mean everything.
And stop
because
hiding
I said
behind
I didn't,
humor.
I didn't care. People might not notice this, but I wasn't very happy before. And when I met you, now I'm happy. So it doesn't matter if anything ever happens.
You're going to cry. Oh, so do you, honey.
See, this is every day.
Now, this ends in murder-suicide.
They cry every day.
Yeah. Restraining orders. There's going to be restraining orders.
Oh,
Pat. No, wait,
I want to be Tristan in Legend of the Fall.
You were sad.
Poe's the older brother.
You were sad when you met Tanya.
Yeah.
And then you're saying what she's done for you, but I mean, like, how are you not sad anymore? Like, what do you see this? You should tell her where you see it's going. So
yeah.
Well, everything. I'd marry her tomorrow, but I'm not the person who'd be worthy of marrying
some
her.
Wedding.
Wow.
Yeah.
Carry over the threshold.
But I'm a mess. When I'm not a mess, I'll pursue that.
Page one.
Right now, we're just we're friends and we're spending time together. That's all I care about.
Get that camera off
putting
me.
Her on a pedestal. Oh, she's getting a phone call. Oh boy.
Oh God, that's never good.
This
who the
guy,
hell's this?
Guy, there you go, Pat.
That's just right. Master Paul.
This is her ex-boyfriend in Missouri.
Yeah. Get your ass down here, girl.
Who's calling you?
I don't know who that
who
was.
Who is that?
Yeah. Oh, I don't know. Wrong
restricted.
Number.
Poe, he's dialing in his thing. Get the fuck away from him.
Let's go to Cleveland. Leo, what's up?
Hey, you guys missed a great line from Ope. She said she left with Patty 2006. He said, what is that, the new model?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Thank you for that, sir.
I found that to be rather hurtful.
Yeah, yes. Well.
And mean-spirited towards Patty.
Oh. All right, we got a break.
All right.
Oh, now there's text messages.
Yeah, there's. All right, who's Pat?
Pat.
You are screaming in a fucking flat spin.
Well, what are you doing? I thought you loved me.
There's no pulling out. I suggest you reach for the handle between your legs, pull it, and punch out because you are going in hot.
You're one of many.
Yeah, watch the canopy goose. It's just, I see it coming. There's no saving this.
If I can't have you, nobody will.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
You know, who knows, man? You might use this as inspiration to become a totally different human
that's
being.
That's exactly what
And you might not want her anymore. Pat. You might get a stripper.
A 25-year-old woman was killed today, and the
and he'll
murderer.
Come walking out bloody going, I did it because I loved her.
I loved her.
Just covered with entrails and splatter. And
yeah.
Make a joke about it.
Brain.
Oh, boy. We got some pictures coming up, yeah.
Where's that?
I guess she models FBA wear.
Oh, cool.
Oh, cool. Very nice.
Nice.
What's wrong with that?
Let's see.
Pat, what's wrong with
Pat? Iggy, we're supposed to take those down.
Pat, why?
Yeah, he never did.
Nice.
Pat, why?
Oh, Jesus.
Nothing wrong with that. Look at that.
Look at Poe. He's getting upset.
Oh, nice.
This is why I told you not to come
into
that
fucking
show.
Poe, I told you she shouldn't have come today.
Pat. This is the love of your life.
I wouldn't mind that so much. You see a girl's breasts and her legs. Wow, way wide open.
Look who's more upset.
In a barn.
Look who's more upset. Poe.
Who put these up? Poe. Who put the pictures up?
Who took them?
I took them.
Wait, well, you're in them.
In Missouri, though.
You're in them. So
and I asked Uncle Inky to took. I took them.
Uncle
on my own.
Uncle Inky.
Holy
wait, wait. You set up a camera with a timer?
No, I just with my webcam in Missouri. I just
sexy
took it with my. You know, I took one hand and.
Oh, I got gotcha. You.
No, no. Those both hands are free.
Yeah. Someone's taking the picture.
No, someone's taking. No.
And that's a little better than a webcam.
Both hands are free. You're lying on the couch, and that's a high megapixel camera. That's not a webcam.
Get back to
that right there is not a webcam. Oh, come on.
I
want to
hear about Uncle Inky.
I know how to Photoshop.
You know how to Photoshop what? You know how to change the resolution of the photograph?
Prototype webcam.
What planet does that work on?
Yeah.
It's a new one that's coming out in 2012.
No, I don't believe it.
Drugged up in that one. Look at that.
So Uncle Inky took...
I took them.
You took them?
But he sent me the clothes, and I took them, and I asked him to take them down, but he never did.
Why didn't he take them down? I thought you guys were friends.
We are friends, but...
What's with Uncle Inky, then?
Yeah, what's up with the Uncle Inky?
Come on, Uncle Inky.
That's Pat's girl.
But you took him yourself?
And Aunt Inky is fine with all this?
Did you blink? What'd you do, blink and then the camera took the picture?
Uncle Inky, there's going to be a leather face in this.
Webcam recorder.
Yeah.
Poe, you don't look very happy about this. What's the matter?
Yeah, Poe isn't happy.
Why aren't you happy?
Poe, get in there.
I'm smiling, I'm fine.
You're not smiling.
No, Poe's,
That's the type of smile of fucking... A German Shepherd has before it bites your fucking bag.
Pretty much, Poe is the last smile you'll see.
Pretty much, Poe has decided someone has to die today.
He's picturing snapping Uncle Inky's neck
or somebody.
Now you've seen these, right? You've been very mad, so you screen capped them so you can have them for like you know when you're fueling awful things. But them being up is offensive, right?
No.
Okay.
They're nice pictures. Very nice.
Yeah.
He's going to be screaming at it.
Artsy.
Which one do you like best?
Hey, Pat, before we go to break, why don't
you... Not a roast beef shot. I mean, you know.
I want Pat to work this a little bit. Let's see, see if you have a shot. Get back on your knee and talk this out with
your knee hurt? You want to sit in my chair?
No, the part about what it's going
to
take for her to like you.
I have to look at the man in the mirror.
Come on, Pat.
I told Michael Jackson.
Here,
before I say anything like that to her.
Do you want
to
sit in my seat because your knee was hurting? You don't have to kneel. You could sit and talk.
Yeah. Have a little talk. We'll just listen.
This isn't very intimate.
But be
talk
sincere.
About happiness
and what
and
you could offer in
future,
the end.
Future, yeah, and
to get your body together and your washboard abs
and your actual washboard that you do the laundry on.
You're growing your hair back in for her. Yeah. You're changing, Pat.
Yeah, Pat's gonna be a gym.
I'm
a gym rat.
A stud.
Come on, Pat.
Let's go, Pat.
Go ahead, Pat. Don't be awkward.
Just leading him on.
When I become the man I want to be, I will pursue you. As to be my girlfriend. And more.
This is way harder to watch.
Smooth, aren't I?
Yeah.
Well,
Pat, no, and you were very sad. We all knew you were sad. Wow. You seem like a different person now.
The petting was a little weird.
I didn't see the petting.
She wasn't very happy. Like, when she took those pictures, she wasn't a happy person doing that.
Right.
She wasn't. And in the past 3 weeks, she's changed a lot.
Because of you.
She's becoming a happy. The last 2 days, we were very happy.
Oh, is he done?
Could you help her become happier?
Yeah. That's my goal in life.
All right, and what do you have to say to what Pat said?
I've seen better shit come out of your mouth about an hour ago, Pat.
Yeah. What?
I care about you a lot, and I'm glad I make you happy, and we all make each other happy.
Yeah.
All made.
And that's all we need. That's all we need for now.
A lot of we. A lot of we.
We.
You understand when a man.
We. I'm going all the way home.
When a man loves a woman as much as he loves you, hearing things like we. And, you know, yeah, we'll be happy.
Who the fuck's we?
Yeah, he doesn't want to hear that.
Why you got to talk to her. Yeah. That's how you got to talk
Come on, Pat.
To her.
Yeah,
well, I'm not in a position where
yes,
I can make
are.
It.
You are.
Me and her.
You no, are. You are.
You're retarded. Yeah. Of course you
ask
are.
Her, you're who, there. Ask her who the hell's calling right now.
Yeah, why can't you, Pat?
Yeah, who the fuck is that on...
It was restricted, so you know it was
Yeah, uh-oh.
How could it be Poe? His hands are out of his pocket. There's a lot of lies going on
he
here.
He dialed his cock. He's a monster.
Why are you saying it's me?
Because you're the only restricted that called
you see?
Me.
Do you have
you
a
see
message?
The argument going on?
Do you have a message?
No, I ran out of minutes, so only Verizon people can call me.
It's Verizon phone or a deadbeat.
Let's you pay a phone bill.
Probably haven't got my paycheck yet.
But you can call other people.
She's waiting for Pat to pay for her. Why not?
I don't pay for my stuff. It's not.
Pat, do you pay her when she goes to work with you?
Yeah, oh yeah. Mm-hmm.
Pat.
Jesus Christ.
I'm not worthy of you.
She's very good because she stays in the van while I do a delivery. I don't have to pay the muni meter and I don't get tickets.
And
I go, Toad.
Pat, by the time this is done, you're going to want to beat her with a parking meter. I'm telling you.
Never.
You are walking with.
We should take a break.
For your own good.
Yeah. All right, guys.
My heart should
Everyone should take a break.
Yeah, a flak jacket or something.
Oh, please. It's so.
Oh, my God.
The tragedy I see.
Why aren't you stomping Pat from Unaki's guts out?
Pat,
be on a
truth.
Toilet
have we
somewhere.
Protected her?
Yes.
Have we taken care of her?
Yes. That was the number one goal.
And we've accomplished
and
quite a bit.
And there's people
haven't
who think
we?
That it's not that.
Exactly.
But it is that.
Well, there's.
We've done miracles.
Yes. Miracles. All right. Well,
they
keep up the good
me.
Work, I guess.
Is that going to be the name of the video?
Whatever. All right,
we've
kids.
We've done miracles.
I'm real happy for all of you.
Yeah.
It's a wonderful relationship.
We're going to take a break. We're going to get Jamie Massad in from the Laugh Factory, okay?
Yes.
All right.
We'll do that next. Joe Rogan in studio.
Menage a bleu.
Playing Carolines all weekend long.
That's some loud bed music, isn't it? Hope he's still zipping his fly up as he walks in. Yeah.
When are they going to fix this microphone, by the way? Jesus, it's annoying. Put my thing back.
You ever watch those shows, Seconds from Disaster?
Yeah.
On Discovery? I love it. It shows, like, what happened, some engineering problems, and the end is unavoidable because of what happened. You see a building collapse. You see a bridge collapse. You see a plane crash. We are watching that with Pat. Seconds from Disaster.
She was on the phone with someone as I was going to the bathroom.
Yeah,
there's a whole thing going on. I'm trying to protect our buddy Pat because he's way out of his league.
He's going
to
be somewhere one of these days at a pest event, and she's going to be making out with some guy, and he's going to just look there like, why can that be me?
She's in the major leagues. He's in peewee ball.
The problem is,
there's not the even. She isn't, though.
Huh?
She's like no. CBA.
CBA?
Yeah, but he's like.
Something's going on there.
Yeah.
What are you saying, Ari?
Yeah, she's, like, pretty good. The problem is, guys like that, his body type get laid all the time. He's just so unconfident.
Yeah, he's no confidence.
Yeah.
Yeah, Joey Diaz.
Yeah.
All right, let's get Jamie Massad in here.
Buddy. Buddy. Buddy, seriously, we have to do something about the N-word. Take it out of dictionary.
For the people that don't know, Jamie Massad is the owner of the Laugh Factory in L.A. where Kramer did his thing.
Obviously,
two nights
Joe Rogan has hurt him a lot.
What's up, brother?
How are you, Joe?
Wonderful, Mr. Masada. And yourself?
I'm doing okay. I'm doing all right, I guess. Trying to do the best we can do with all of the comedians that are surrounding you guys. And, you know, especially Joe and everybody in here, they're thinking of what I did with banning the N. It was kind of like a...
You mean the word nigger?
Please be nice.
Can't say it.
You know,
just say that it's
we're
a word.
Talking about the word.
No,
just a word.
I know, but the whole
not
thing.
Not calling anybody. Yet.
I know, but the thing happened. You know, you guys, you were here, you didn't see it. I mean, I was in the Los Angeles. The time is South Central. All of the sudden, everybody they're trying to have a riot and all of that stuff happening. You got to do the best you can to stop it.
So are you doing this for self-preservation? Is this pretty much please, look, I'm trying. Don't burn my club down.
No, 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 no. It's not only that.
Or is
no.
it a personal no, decision no. that you're yeah, actually making through your own morality or something?
Yeah, because we can't start banning words there.
No,
yeah,
you can't. No way. No,
start
no,
banning the
no,
word.
No, no, no. I'm not banning a word or anything like that whatsoever. What I'm trying to say, we got it as a comedy community, we got to come together somehow. You know, calm the whole thing down because of it's South Central, all of the people, all of the Senate up there, they're all ready to do the riot.
Oh, come on.
And we did
still,
have
no way. They're still angry about a sitcom guy from years ago who said a bad word to a heckler trying to hurt him.
And then he really apologized poorly.
Fell apart on television over and over again with Al Sharpton and Jesse Jackson and David Letterman. I mean, if they're really ready to riot, if they're going to riot, they would have already rioted. No,
they were going to riot.
But not gonna riot now.
No, no, they were going riot. I mean, at the time we were day before Thanksgiving, I was on a Stevie Wonder's radio, a bunch of places was there were 5,000-6,000 of people that were outside. Mm-hmm. They were all kind of like it was like a dynamite, it was ready to blow up.
Right.
And so what we do, we have to do something because in Los Angeles, these people, there are a lot of people, they are unemployed, there are a lot of people, they don't have no jobs, anything in South Central, and it was just going crazy. So what do you do at that point? You got to do something the best you can do, calm everything down.
I think you calm things down, though, by telling Michael Richards maybe that he can't perform there anymore because it was more, not so much for the language, but just for like the outburst and the turning away of your clientele. You know, he turned away people from your club. That is a reason for you to say, hey, you're not welcome back here anymore.
Yeah,
but for using words, I mean, it's like if Mencia comes in and says Beaner, 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 are you going to ban him? Is it something like
no,
that?
No, no, no. I mean, none of
he
that. You know, no, but, yeah. You know, the whole thing is what we're trying to do. The time you see the whole thing happening, what's happening in Los Angeles, you guys all see it from outside. The time I was involved with it, the time I saw it in Los Angeles.
Well, I could nigger out what's going on out there. It's hard to figure out.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I can figure out what's going on out there just by what I hear in the news.
Oh, they're applauding. You are
things like that, but I'm sorry, it was just a Freudian slip. But I don't think it's as bad.
I'm
but
there.
Again, I'm not.
Well,
out
I'm there
yet.
Too. It's
no, but you guys, you are all, you know, everybody. Joe Rogan, everybody, they are there. They're living in Beverly Hills, Brentwood.
I don't live in Beverly Hills.
Oh, okay, whoever. You're not living in South Central. The time you go into South Central.
If I lived in South Central, would it make more sense?
I think you would be agreeing with me if you leave there.
I think Jamie is afraid of his club. This is why I didn't hate that you banned it.
Jamie
only
was
because
right.
I didn't look at it like it was a political correct decision. I think he just didn't want his club to be a focal point of this rage with that big insignia on the side. And that's an area that has a history of really shitty racial violence. And look, if I owned a building, I just don't want people fucking Molotov cocktailing it. I mean, so that's the only reason I kind of sided with you on that. Huh. I don't think banning a word, I think it's disgraceful.
But here's how,
to preserve your club from being burnt down, you know, you got to do something.
Here's how it could have been stopped way, way earlier. Why didn't you get rid of those fuckheads but when they were heckling other people? Weren't they heckling other people all night?
No, no, they was not.
That's what I heard from other comics.
No, I was there. You're just hearing all people, they're exaggerating. I was there. The guys, they were ordering drinks. By the time and a couple of days they were talking, I was right there. And one of the guys, and Michael looked at the people. He said, what's going on in here? And the guy said nothing. And Michael kept on asking, what's going on? Why you talk? And the guy, he said, hey, my buddy think you're not funny. He said, what? He said, my buddy said, you're not funny. And at that point, the rage just came in. And, you know, comics, they are, you know, I mean, all of you guys know you're coming from insecurity. You're coming from, you need a lot of love on the stage. And that's what it is about.
Yeah,
and
but at that point, it's like you make fun of the guy's shirt. You could talk about his big head. That's the thing. Like, you're saying, it's like, you should never do what he did. You should never do that.
No, no,
he's
because
he's so incompetent. That's what it really is.
Dude, it's like, if you're bombing, that's what happens in comedy. People say you're not funny, and then you have to deal with it.
Right.
What you don't do
is what he did was fucking wrong.
Well, I had heard from he had did a set at the Comedy Store before he went up at the Laugh Factory, and the guys who saw him at the Comedy Store, my friend Brian was talking about him saying he was like a different guy. He was like yelling and screaming and swearing. He just seemed like all amped up.
He had a chick with him, right?
He had a chick with him.
That might explain why that rage came out, because there's nothing worse than bombing in front of a girl.
You know why?
It's
that
fucking
chick
embarrassing.
She's living at Poe's house.
Oh. She's being protective.
She's in a cage right now.
Would it help with the Laugh Factory, though, if they wanted to cut the problem, if they just banned black patrons?
Yeah.
That's an option.
I mean, when you call
a white guy a nigger, they very rarely even flinch.
I don't think so, any of that would have <there.
laughs> He's actually answering it. No, I don't think that would actually be the right way to do it.
Buddy, that's not the way to handle.
Wait, I got a question.
Start slow with drinking fountains in bathrooms.
Four different restrooms.
No, but, you know, the whole thing was the time this whole rage went on, and all of this, and I didn't know what to do, and all I did, I mean, after 28 years of being in the business, I decided I'd give everybody's money back, and a lot of people, they start taking advantage of a lot of opportunities that were there.
Yep.
You know, a guy coming in, he said, I have $400 worth drinks. I said, $400
worth? You drank them.
I said, I mean, $400. I said, show me the bill. He showed me a knife. I said, okay, here's $400.
He showed you a knife?
Yeah.
Oh,
I mean, I wish
boy.
You were there that
wait
night.
Wait a minute. The guy pulled a knife on you?
Yeah.
Why didn't you call the police?
Here's
because
my bill.
Because at that time, it was going to be a riot.
Yeah, right.
You guys, you're seeing outside, you don't see what was going on up there. It was amazing stuff was happening. All of a sudden, a lot of people, Jesus. The opportunists, they are standing up there, they looking at everything. It just doesn't make sense. For you guys, you know, sitting up here, why don't you, at that point, by the time I'll call the cops and that and that and that.
Listen, it is pandemonium. I totally understand you giving people their money back, apologizing. I totally understand you banning Michael Richards. I totally understand all that.
I just don't understand you printing receipts on knives.
No.
Stupid fucking move.
Handed out a Laugh Factory knife.
Jesus.
Complimentary Laugh Factory switchblade.
A lot of engraving going on. Thank God.
Paul Mooney will carry it around.
Oh, please, homie.
And put
the knife away, homie. Wait.
And, of course, Paul Mooney get on all of that. And Jesse Jackson and all of those guys, they're all coming. Are you going on a radio show with them? All of them, they have their hands out. Oh, you got to do something for my church.
Well, this Paul guy Mooney, gotta, I think, made a great point. You said the guy had a nervous breakdown. I think that's exactly what it was. He's just not a funny guy. I mean, that's the reality of it. He got all that love all those years from those sitcoms, and that's, look, man, I've been in that fucking world from news radio. I've seen those people. That's, they want their bagels and their smoked lox, and they're there at the table read, and everyone's clapping and laughing, and there's all this extra love, and everyone waves to them on the red carpet, and it's a bullshit world.
Yeah.
And you go from that bullshit world to the fucking trenches of Saturday night in front of drunks at a comedy club. Dude, that's a different animal,
and it's
man.
His words coming out of his mouth, not Larry David's or Jerry Seinfeld's or the writers.
Not only is it his words, he doesn't have that much time on stage. He's only been doing time. I mean, how long has he been doing comedy?
About 6 months, 7 months.
Oh, no, he's been doing it longer than that. I've seen him at the Comedy Store several years ago.
He came in, but he stopped. He came in for 1 month, 2 months.
He's been
and
doing
he
it in other places. He's been doing other places because I saw him at the Improv at least a year ago.
Yeah,
so he's been scattered back and forth going on stage, but the bottom line is the guy is up at one of the biggest stages in the country as far as stand-up goes. You know, you're going there, you're going to go up after all these major national acts who are going to fucking slay, and then you're going up basically an open micer who's a superstar multimillionaire, and on top of it, he's got this fucking tremendous attitude. Mm. You know, I mean, you know, the shit that he said was just, that's insanity. I mean, you can't say that. I mean, none of it makes any sense.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, someone doesn't think you're funny, so you're going to hang them up by their ankles and stick a fork in their ass and, look, I found a nigger. None of that makes any sense.
The funniest part was in the middle of it where he tried to turn it around and try to play it like he was trying to teach people something.
Hey, they're just words.
Oh, those words. We're still, it's like, no, dude, you fucking snapped.
Snapped. Yeah, that was what's in your mind. It's like
Mooney hit it the best. Mooney said he had a nervous breakdown. Yeah.
And is in a way he did. He did in a point. He did have a nervous breakdown. And then he wanted to come in to talk to the people.
Did you let him on stage the next night?
No, he told me he want to come in next night to go apologize. I said, okay, Michael, come in. And CNN, they came in with the camera. Jennifer Wolf came in with a CNN. They wanted to have him on the stage to apologize. He went on the stage, and he was on the stage for 5-6 minutes. He didn't apologize. We gave him red light. And you know what's the red light? People, they don't know out there.
He didn't apologize. What did he
no.
do?
And he ran off the stage, and he went to Jennifer. He said, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. And Jennifer said, we wanted you to say it on the camera. He said no, and he ran out of the door. That's the end of it.
So he went on stage. What did he talk about for 6 minutes?
The Japs.
About 4 or 5 minutes. He just went.
What's the deal?
You know, I mean.
Yeah, what did he do, though? This is an interesting question.
No, but he went on. He was nervous, and I think he was doing some of the jokes, but he was. The time he goes on the stage. First of all, you know that, Joe, because you've been into it, because you were a star, and on your star, the time you go on the stage, people, they go crazy because of you go on the stage. And he went on the stage for 5 minutes, 3 minutes, people, they went crazy to see him. And
They went crazy to see him. Did they know about
the YouTube video? Wasn't out yet.
Some of them they do. Some of them they
do. Did anybody boo him?
Not really. They were waiting for him to apologize. You know, and then all of a sudden, he got off the stage. He ran off the stage.
Oh, man, he blew it.
You know, it was
He should have checked into rehab. I would have said I was on a pound of coke.
DMT.
Don't you think remember that night? DMT. I'm pissing blood.
You put Velcro DMT. On the ceiling.
This is the last thing you'd say.
Yeah. You wet their lips and stick them to the wall. Yeah. Nothing, people. Three, if you slice them thin enough.
Don't you think banning words, though, sets a real bad precedent for club owners?
I don't, you know, it's just like a again, all of you guys know, and
you're in a really,
Joe, you know,
you're in a tough position, though, because the other... Yeah. Other races are going to come out and say, well, you got to ban spick, and you got to ban this word, you got to ban that, gook.
Chink. Faggot.
What about hacks? How about ban hacks first?
Ban hacks.
Or do you let,
yeah, no, what it really is.
Or do you let
is,
the word appear eventually on that stage
say,
again?
You can't say that shit in anger. Like,
right. Yeah, no,
just
I,
deliberately trying to piss. But there's
I get the way around shit. That is if someone does that, you don't
right.
book them again.
Yeah.
But people are thinking, he's dealing with the fucking media circus.
Like,
he's got to do something.
Yeah. He's also got to deal with the fact that 20 Asians aren't going to come to his place if someone says chink and stab him with chopsticks.
Well, they got the Chinese stars
in certain situations, in the area you're in, there is an element that might be a little angry and riled to the point where they might do some physical damage.
No, Jamie, what about Black Knight? You do a Black Knight,
yeah,
over there, right?
Yeah, we do. We do a Chocolate Sunday.
So how
Sunday.
Are you going to do that?
I mean,
Chocolate Sunday. You doing Chocolate Sunday? They're not allowed to say the N-word.
Yes. And what?
No. That's
hilarious.
No fucking way.
I bet the first guy gets up there.
No, please, homie.
Even Paul Mooney came in on Wednesday night. Paul Mooney came last Wednesday.
Exactly. 3 minutes long.
No, he did not use one word.
How about that Elizabeth Taylor? Homie.
That Negro is crazy.
Why did the cameras leave? Oh, homie,
I'm ready
stop.
For my
African-American, please.
But I just got to finish
ready for my N-word wake-up call.
You know, one thing I'm going to say is it was like, you know, pro sports, they say you got to be nice to fan if you are going to be a little bit crazy.
I don't think
fan,
those
gotta,
guys were his fans.
Well, you know, yeah. The people, they come in the club, they are comedy fans.
Not Michael Richards fans.
No, I want to say, I mean, every other people, they come in the club, they shouldn't use the word because of, we say, if you do it, we take some of your money from your paycheck, we give it to charity. That's what we're going to try to do. And that's right now calming people down. You got to do something. You can't just, you know, say, no, we are not going
how
to do
much?
It.
You did your yeah, but wait a minute, you get like $50 a set or something. What do you get a set at the left hand?
Yeah, 75, not like another.
How much money comedy store, they rip you off, those cocksuckers.
I never got a check from anybody in L.A. No? I never got paid in L.A.
I don't get paid at the comedy
You never
store.
Got paid from Laugh Factory?
No, from no one. No one's ever paid me in L.A.
Oh, you better go in cashier booths. Always your check is there.
Buddy, it's ready
so
for
somebody,
you.
Let's say someone gets on stage. Buddy.
Unless one of the black people steal.
So, no,
someone gets on stage.
They hang them by
in a very comedic context.
Yes.
They use the word nigger.
And it's going to happen.
How much is it going to cost?
One of the boys are going to do gonna, that.
First, it's going to take their paycheck, go to a charity.
Their whole paycheck.
A whole
so
paycheck.
It would call, how much money is that?
$75.
$75. $75.
Yes.
If you blurt that word out.
If it's worth it if you get a good laugh.
And what if you say it twice? Does that affect your next set?
Then you're going to be, for 3 months, you won't be able to come back to the Laugh Factory. That's crazy.
So first time you find them, then the second time, the 3 months off?
Yeah.
It's still worth it. There's a comedian out there that's going to do it just for the exposure.
Yeah, what about
going to be the guy that breaks the ban and he's going to be all over CNN?
Have you ever done something similar to this for guys who steal material?
Well, I've done that many times. You know that.
Doesn't Mencia perform at your club all the time?
Hello. Don't even go there. You know that. Yeah.
Doesn't he?
No.
You stopped him?
From first day. Come on.
What?
You know better than that.
Come on.
The Mencia
Logan Battle Royal. Oh, dude.
You know,
come on, man.
You know,
He's there. He goes there.
Yeah, but, you know, not in, you know, most of the people, they do anything like that.
What about Dane?
What about Dane?
Dane Cook. Yes. What about him stealing people's material?
Dane, he does not steal anybody.
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about?
That's hilarious. Go on the internet. Go on the internet and watch all the videos, listen to all the people talk about it. You ever see the Louis C.K. clips?
Yeah.
When Louis C.K. was working out his material for his HBO special, and Dane did three of his bits on a CD? Blatantly?
Who took from who?
No. Dane takes from everybody. Louis C.K. doesn't steal from anybody. Louis C.K. is a great comedian. I've never heard one person ever say that he steals from anybody. Every comic that I know says Dane Cook steals.
No, Dane Cook. I have not seen something.
Because he's your number one guy, buddy, does not mean he doesn't steal.
Joe.
Buddy, tell the truth.
Don't
speak with fucking tongue.
No, I tell you something. Dane Cook, he's a most hardworking guy.
Yes, very hardworking, very ambitious.
Everybody, and let me tell you, everybody jealous of him. They're trying to undercut him.
True.
Oh, he's this.
Very
okay,
true.
What else you can come in? Because he have number one record, he have number one everything.
But
what?
They've always said he was a thief way before that.
No, they did not.
Yes, they did.
As soon as he made it, everybody jumped.
No. Way before. That's not true.
I never heard of it. No. As soon as he made it.
Have you ever heard this?
I have heard it. Well, the problem was when the clip showed up online, it got to be ugly because between Louis and Dane, the clips were there, and it was like, oof.
It's obvious.
Yeah, but not with the internet.
But it's not just him. It's Jim Brewer. He's stolen from me. He's stolen from a million different comics in L.A.
He didn't want that cutting at times. Like you said, Chappelle, I mean, when comics make it, a lot of times comics aren't jealous. No comics are ever jealous or bad about Dave Attell or Louis Black. There's a lot of guys that
or
make
CK,
it.
Or Chappelle. I mean, Chappelle's enormous.
Oh. Chappelle's a good example because he's so
Nobody. Nobody says he steals, ever. Everyone says Dane steals.
Yeah, but let me explain something.
You're not telling the truth.
I'm telling the truth.
No,
what
you're not.
Yes.
Bro, but it's not true. It's not a truth. I'm not saying you're a liar, but I'm saying you might not be aware of it. It's definitely not true.
I mean, the only thing I'm saying, as soon as I see his record, his CD came number one, and he went on the chart. He became, after Steve Martin, he was the first person going up the chart. Nobody ever done it. And everybody got jealous. Everybody started calling.
But that doesn't mean anything. You're avoiding the
point.
I'm not avoiding something.
He did
do a tremendous thing, and he was very successful, but the fact remains, he stole material.
On that CD, he took stuff from Louis C.K.'s HBO special from years before.
That's a fact.
But show it to me. Show it to me.
I mean,
you say, come on, Jamie.
You're a great diplomat, by the way.
Hey, Joe, where is it online?
I'm not.
You can find it online.
I think you can go
to redband.com. I think he's got it up. I think, there's a whole Radar magazine is printing it. They're doing an article right now about him stealing. There's like a bunch of, he's been accused of it on CNN, had a whole thing about comics saying that he steals. I mean, it's all over the place. Where there's smoke, there's fire. I've never met a single comic ever that people say steals that doesn't steal. Have you? Bill, have you ever met a guy that everybody says is a thief, and you see the guy and goes, no, this guy's completely original. I've never heard one.
The only thing I remember was guys, I'm not going to say names, but just one guy who made it, and it's just everybody where I was at was saying, this guy took from me, this guy took from me, this guy took from me, and I was looking at their acts, and I didn't see it.
Who is this? This doesn't make sense unless you give us context.
Yeah, if you didn't think he was a thief, you could say it. Because you're not.
Yeah, Leary. Like everyone's saying, Leary took
that. Oh, dude,
the
Hick stuff is pretty.
I don't know anything about it. I'm just saying that.
Well, you never listened to the Hick stuff. I saw Leary steal over and over again back in Boston, early in the '80s, in the late '80s rather, the early '90s. I saw it. I saw it with my own eyes, over and over and over again.
I saw him do Ray Romano's material.
I saw him do Tony V's material. I saw it with my own eyes in clubs. I saw him do Bill Hicks material.
verbatim. Then I saw Bill Hicks do the same material a month later, and I was baffled. I was an open micer. And I said, what the fuck is going on?
I saw guys who stunk in their acts. Nobody would steal from. We're walking around saying it.
Okay, that's. I'm sure
like,
there's
the
a lot of that. Of course, there's delusional.
I never
people.
Saw. That's delusional.
Of course,
yes.
Of course, there's that. But the fact remains that guy's a thief. That's a fact.
Larry,
for sure, I've seen it over and over again. I saw it with my own eyes. I mean, he doesn't anymore. But if you look at the difference between you look at his first No Cure for Cancer, then look at Locked and Loaded. Pre and post Hicks being dead, dude, there's a monstrous difference in the level of the material. The material post Hicks being dead is fucking horrible. The stuff that he did before, when No Cure for Cancer, is some brilliant shit.
Yeah,
it's a completely different thing because he was taking the ideas from someone else. That is a fact.
Yeah, but Joe, if I can say something here, you're very fast to jump in a conclusion of
somebody. Do you know why? Because I've been the victim of it.
I've seen it happen over
and over again. And because I work very hard on my material and I write a lot and I sit in front of my fucking computer for hours on end and then I go to the Comedy Store and I have little pieces of paper and I go over it in my head. Which bitch am I going to do? I'm going to go into that. Then I go into that. And I work on this shit over and over and over again for months. And then some fucking douchebag goes up, he sees me kill with some bit, and then he reworks it, and then he goes on stage. And you know what? Club owners don't do shit about it, and then they get on here on a radio show, and they say, no one steals, he doesn't steal.
What,
and it's not true. No. You haven't looked into it at all, and you're defending someone who is widely known throughout the country as being a thief through the fucking comedy community. You talk to club owners, you talk to people in HBO, you talk to people everywhere that I talk to people, they know he steals.
Okay, let me explain something. Doesn't mean you telling me you thought of a material. Doesn't mean somebody else. If you thought of building a helicopter, and doesn't mean another person, another place does not be able.
There is
to
a thing
see.
Called parallel thinking. Yes.
Yeah, it's, and then
I've
you.
Had that
you
happen
can,
to me.
Yeah, but you
sure,
cannot.
I've had that happen too. I had that happen recently. We were just talking about it. A buddy of mine in L.A. said, "Dude, I got this bit. It's like your bit." I go, don't even worry about it. You know, I know you're not a thief. You know, if you know a guy's not a thief, it's like you don't even have the conversation. You know, if you got a comic that you know you respect, like, dude, it's a fucking common, it's something happened in the news and you thought about something and I thought about something and they're similar.
But I think sometimes if people are already jealous of a guy's success and then that parallel thinking happens, it's just become, once you get to a certain level, it immediately becomes, he's a thief.
Without a doubt. There are definitely crabs in a bucket. With the Dane Cook thing, they were calling him a thief. They were calling him a thief for years. Years ago, they were calling him a thief. I had a problem with him way back when. He was doing one of my bits on Premium Blend. He did my bit about tigers fucking on the Discovery Channel. He changed it to rhinos. I called him up. He told me his own fucking agent told him to stop doing the bit, and he was going to stop doing it. Then I came to the Laugh Factory, and he's doing one of my other bits on stage. I confronted him, and that was the last time I worked at the Laugh Factory. I don't work there anymore because I didn't want to go up in front of him and see him doing my shit and have him go up and do it. But I never thought Dane was going to make it. I, like a lot of people, thought that Dane was like a mediocre comic. I mean, he's a fantastic self-salesman, a great marketer, a genius strategist as far as like marketing himself and promoting himself. I mean, you got to give the guy massive amounts of credit for that tireless worker in that regard. But I never thought he was very funny. So I didn't worry about the repercussions of him stealing material. I heard it from everybody over and over again. Comics were saying that he's stealing their shit. He's telling them to stop doing bits they've been doing for years because that's their bit. He's gonna sue them. I mean, I heard it from everybody. You've heard it. We've all heard it. It's like, it's not because the guy got famous. That's bullshit. He was getting this reputation long before. For sure, there's crabs in a bucket, and for sure, there's when people get famous, people try to drag them down. But that's not what's going on here.
Yeah, but again, you got to look at it the way I look at it.
Yeah, you look at it as a club owner, and he puts asses in your seat.
No,
that's how you're looking at it.
That's not the reason.
Come on, what's the reason?
He's been working there 12 years,
right.
And a lot of people, they came to me. The same time, he came with a joke. Another person came out with a joke. The joke you're talking about, Discovery and Tigers and all of that. Everybody can do that joke. And you saying to me, well, somebody see that joke. It cannot be done. Another person.
I got a call from Jim Brewer. Jim Brewer was working with Dane Cook in Canada. And Jim Brewer called me up and he goes, dude, fucking Dane Cook's doing your material.
Now,
verbatim. In Kent, 8 years ago. It was a long time ago. And then I heard he did it on Premium Blend, and that's when I called him up. And Dane and I used to be friends. I was friends with that guy. He used to open up for me back in Boston when he was with Al and the Monkees. He was at a sketch group. And, you know, I've known him for a long time. He's always had that reputation. He's always had
On that CD, there's 3 bits from this Louis C.K. HBO special
that are nearly word for word. He'll change one word and it's almost exactly.
Dude, I'm a huge comedy fan, and I love it when people make it, and I love being inspired. I love watching good comedy, and I'm not one that believes that if someone becomes successful, that means that other people aren't successful. I think that there's enough success out there for everybody, and I want everybody to be huge. I mean, I want everybody to, who's a great comic to get out there and have a bunch of people enjoy their work, but that's not what's going on here.
Well, to me, again, maybe some of a lot of stuff, I'm not saying you, a lot of comics that I spoke to, I see they're coming from jealousy.
You think Louis C.K. is coming from jealousy?
I don't know. Louis C.K., for example, one of the jokes that he particularly talks about, I seen it. Dane Cook was working on the stage much before Louis C.K.
How long?
I don't know, about maybe 9 months before Louis.
Yeah, Louis had those jokes for about 6 years.
Okay, 6 years. But
and Dane seen those jokes.
But you don't know if Dane seen it or he saw it on the TV or sometimes it came in. Or you saying,
He saw him. Louis was in the audience, and Louis was on stage, and Dane was in the audience. Louis talked to Dane after he did sets. He talks about it. About a Dane saw him do the material.
Again, we all make an accusation without, you know.
We're not making accusations.
Let's have Louis and Dane start talking to each other, say this has happened. You saying stuff.
Why are you defending him? Why are you openly defending
because
him?
Because I'm openly defending him because of, I think a lot of people, they came to the club. I'm the only club. If I see.
You're
proof,
the only club?
I'm the only club.
The only club, what do you mean?
The only club I ban people if Carlos Mencia, any of that stuff. Paul Mooney came in, said Carlos Mencia did his jokes. I was in Laugh Factory. I said, Carlos, you cannot do that anymore.
But he
you
still performs at your club.
No, he doesn't.
He doesn't ever perform at your club.
Except, only one time he came.
Come on, he wasn't there recently?
No, he came one time with a showcase for the,
Okay, well, I'm being lied to then because someone told me they saw him here very recently and they've seen him at your club a couple times.
Well, I mean, if they've seen him, I don't know, but personally.
So it's when you're not there that he performs.
I mean, I'm there all the time, but if
okay, so you're admitting that Carlos steals. You know Carlos steals?
I don't know Carlos. Again, Carlos, but let me explain. I admit it, Carlos. Let me explain it to you. With Carlos. Carlos, I admit it.
Call him by a slave name.
Okay.
Call him Ned.
Ned, or whatever. Is the whole thing is, I'm just trying to say, I saw Carlos and George Lopez, they were upstairs, they were, you know, almost killing each other.
Yeah, I was actually in the lobby when George Lopez grabbed him by the neck and threw him
up. No, it wasn't in the lobby, it was upstairs in my club. It was upset.
I thought it was in the front, bro.
No. I mean,
it might have happened more than once.
I mean, I saw it. I tried.
What happened with Lopez and Carlos? I don't get all the
skinny. Carlos stole all Lopez's shit and did it on his HBO special. Carlos is more subtle about his stealing now, but in the early days, it was fucking horrible. It was just blatant, verbatim, just giant chunks of material. He's not a creative guy. I mean, if you talk to the guy, he's not very intelligent. He doesn't have an unusual point of view, and he just steals.
Him and Lopez had a beef in the club.
He's had a beef with everybody, bro. Mooney, Lopez.
I've seen a lot of people, they get in a fight and everything, and the time they came in to me, they told me about it, and I find out if they did it, then I try to react on it and do whatever I can. Mm-hmm. And to come in to tell me, oh, as soon as somebody make it and everybody jealous and trying to put him down, I'll say something about
Louis, though. Louis did not push. I will say this because I know Louis well. Louis didn't push that issue. He actually, we were talking about it one time on the set, and he's like, nah, man, I don't want to get into it, and talk about it publicly, just because then it seems like you're bashing the guy who's getting famous. So Louis actually tried to be very low-key about that whole thing.
I had a conversation with him about it, and I said, dude, you're not going to come off bitter if you're just honest about it. You don't have to, you know, let a guy get away with something like that. You can talk about it and not come off bitter. It is possible.
Yeah, but again, okay, everything, all right, he stole this, he stole that, but everything he's made so far, he made his movie, became number one, he stole.
That doesn't
he stole
mean anything. No, bro,
it's a
we're not talking
guy.
About the fucking movies, man. We're talking about comedy.
Yeah, we're talking about comedy
that's a big deal?
And everything
you're making it like it's not a big deal.
A lot of times people don't know
until
they see these CDs that become number one on the charts. Once they see it, once it's out there, they're like, "Oh, that's
the real." The real thing about Dane is Dane would have made it without stealing. Dane made it because he's brutally ambitious and he's a very smart guy.
He's a talented too.
And very talented performer.
I
believe all that.
Yeah,
I,
you're not. Leaving. Okay.
All right, I'm back.
I'm sorry.
Louis C.K. Dane Cook.
Okay.
Got some audio.
Because you haven't heard this yet, right?
Let's see it. Yeah, please.
All right. Let's see if you have a comment. So this is Louis C.K., obviously. Listen closely.
One time I saw a guy in a bicycle, and he was about to get hit with a car door. It was horrible. And he wasn't looking, and the lady opening the door wasn't looking. It was just, like, just for me. And I didn't know what to do. I was like, ah! Like, I wanted to yell something, but what do you yell? And I'm trying to, like, if time slows down, I'm trying to choose the thing to yell that will have all the information that he needs. Because it was happening really fast. I had, like, that much time to yell, you know, what can I yell in that much time? This, hey, you got to buy out! Hang on, that's not... She can open the door again! Shit! I just yelled out, bad thing! Wasn't really specific enough. Oh, well.
So there you have it, Louis C.K. Now, what's that from? You know offhand, Joe?
Oh, it's, I don't know. One of his HBO specials, or is it a CD?
This goes back a while.
I saw Louis do that years ago. I actually don't know where
it's
from.
It's like 2000. It's like from
2001, they're saying. All right. And now here's Dane Cook.
3 weeks.
Okay, can I comment on that?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, absolutely.
We're playing it for you.
Okay. That particular thing, I know Dane Cook. He came to me. He said he saw an accident really happen. Now, you guys coming up say, because of, you know, it was recorded so much. If something happened to somebody.
But dude, he saw that bit. That's the same bit.
No, it saw this accident happen.
That's all well and good. You see an accident doesn't mean you're allowed to take someone's bit to describe the accident. And that's what he did. He described it exactly the same way he saw Louis C.K. describe it. That's a stolen bit.
Well, to me, the time he described the accident happened to him...
That doesn't mean anything.
That does mean to something, because
no,
if something happened to you, Joe Rogan, if somebody punched you in the face or something, yeah. And you're going to talk
Are
about
you
it, you can't
me?
Say, you can't say, no, I... No.
Are you falling apart here, Jamie?
No. I mean, I'm saying somebody
Jamie, you're punch. Falling apart
no,
here,
No, I'm not.
That's a stolen bit.
No, it's not.
Can we get a consensus here? How many people believe that was a stolen bit?
It's very close.
Yeah,
it's
pretty close.
If everyone in the peanut gallery just raised their hands, everyone out there,
here's
Bill Burr, is that a stolen bit?
If something happens to you, I see people on stage and they'll do a bit. I'll be like, oh my God, that same stuff happened exactly to me.
I had a bit one time, and I swear to God, another guy came out. He had a bit, and it was like fucking the setup
that
we had were like word for fucking word, and I got all paranoid. I started inventing this conspiracy, like, this guy's on a TV show, he had writers, and they were in this Chinese restaurant that I was performing in out in fucking Worcester, and they saw it, and then I just, after a while, I just realized that, like...
That is possible.
Like...
Parallel thinking, we already discussed
that.
But this is not a case
Greg
of parallel
Giraldo
thinking.
Had a bit about...
Again,
we're talking about 6 years before, and during those years, and before that, he was doing the bit. Before he recorded it in 2001, he was doing that bit before, and he's been doing it, and then Dane comes along and puts it on a CD in 2005. You don't think he saw that?
You know what the thing is? People definitely steal. They definitely swipe shit. They definitely switch shit up. But actually fucking proving it is what sucks.
Yeah. Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Because
Thank
people
you.
Rewrite things.
Or being paranoid. Being a paranoid,
Jamie,
Joy.
There's nothing paranoid
it
about
is
that.
Paranoid.
That
it is
Jamie,
paranoid.
There's nothing paranoid about what you just heard.
No, because I heard the other part of the story. You don't want to face
the
other part
of the story. Doesn't mean
the guy, he was almost in an accident. You don't want to hear that. You want to hear what
okay,
happened.
Okay, let's look at it this way. You know Chris Rock's joke about tossing your salad? You know that joke he does about watching that prison show? Now, what if I watch the same prison show, and I go on stage and do a joke very similar about tossing your salad? Even though I know Chris Rock had done that joke, for 5 fucking years about tossing your salad. That would be stealing material, Jamie. That's what that is.
Okay, let me
even though I saw the show, even though I saw the same show he saw, it's still stealing material when you know another guy did the exact same fucking thing.
Yeah, that's that rule of who got there first.
Okay, no, I understand.
It's the same
setup.
All right, listen, that could have been parallel thinking. Let's go to another.
Can I make one comment?
No, Tommy, what do you think?
No, that's way too close.
Well, let it's ceiling, right? You think it's ceiling?
Yeah.
Okay. Anthony, what do you think?
Joe, we have a soft. We have a soft spot for this because in radio the same shit
happens to you guys all the time.
Okay, can I say something?
One example. Let's see what happens.
Okay.
Here's another example.
You have to say it too. Like, I never jumped on a Dana stealing bandwagon, only because I know a lot of people attack somebody when a guy's getting. You have to see how many instances it happens in. Like, if you hear one bit and you go, like,
it
was one bit. Absolutely.
There
is something that can be very close.
If you have an open mind,
all
right, fine. Parallel.
Yeah, let's
try another one.
But you guys
don't
know.
Let's try another one.
You don't want to listen to me.
Well, you'll have your say.
Okay, thank you.
Here's another example. Louis C.K. first.
My wife and I were thinking of having a baby and. I'd like to have a kid, because you can name your kid anything you want. I like that part. I'd like to give my kid an interesting name, you know? Like a name with no vowels, maybe, you know? Just like... Just like 40 Fs, that's his name. Go clean your room, you know, something like that.
All right, so that's Louis C.K. from 2001.
Louis is a fucking an original guy, man. Louis is a very out there original guy.
Yeah, weird. All right, here's Dane Cook.
Very weird.
I think about having kids. I'd love to have some kids. I've been thinking about kids. I want to have, like, 19 kids. I think naming them, that's going to be fun. Whatever the names that you come up with, that's exciting right there. You get to both decide, hey, do you want to name that? No, I don't like that name. Right? It's like a little game. You try to come up. I already have names picked out. I don't even know. First kid, boy, girl, I don't care. The first one that comes out, I'm naming it. I think it's beautiful. It's feminine but strong at the same time. Time for bed. I said time for bed. No cookies.
Oh, boy. Well,
what do you have to say about that one, James?
This is what I'll say here. This is what I'll say now. One can happen. I don't know. This is, you know.
Where there's smoke, there's fire.
Yeah,
look, I used to like the guy, too, until he stole from me. It's not an uncommon discussion amongst comedians.
That's almost word for word, Jamie. What do you got to say?
Okay, let me explain something, you guys.
We wouldn't be surprised if you just start yelling nigger a lot.
Stop even going there, $75,
Opie. $75.
Why are you going there? Okay, let me
explain. We'll see. We're going to watch it. Let me tell you.
Let's let Jamie.
Blurting that word out was a lot cheaper back in the 1800s.
Okay, let me. Dane Cook is one thing about Dane Cook. He goes up there. He talks. He's not like a comedian that go write the material. And he like accent happen, like the time he goes on the stage, somebody was talking to him about kids and something like that. And he just blobs whatever comes to his mind. Maybe the thought of the same thought was going on. He doesn't write the material. He goes up there. He make up the material right on the spot. And he's not like, he's commenting what's happened to him. And again, this one, I would say he went on the stage and something happened to the kids or something. One time, I got to tell you one thing so you clarify something. Let me explain something.
Wow, you're
please.
In denial,
okay,
bro.
No, I'm
deep.
Not in denial.
Can I finish?
It's
not true because he says that joke all the time. Okay. It's not like someone yelled at him, what about kids, Dane? And then he just said, I want to name a kid with a lot of letters together. Even though I've never heard anybody do that before.
Okay. And I will say, even though the bits are very similar, I did kind of enjoy Dane's bit, too.
Did you enjoy it?
He does it with the
mosh. Fuck you.
I got to tell you something. One time, Los Angeles Times was doing an article about Robin Williams being taking material from other people.
Yeah. True.
And they call me, everybody, they talk to everybody in the industry, everybody. They say, yeah, Robin doing that. Robin did that on Tonight Show. Robin did that on From Me Here. Robin did that. But for Robin,
My only thing is seeing him to what he's doing on the stage and how long he's been doing it. Robin is a type of person, he's addictive to laughter. And that's what I said.
We call him attention whores.
I don't know if it's it just doesn't, like a drug addict, is he need a fix. The time he's on the stage, he need the laughter.
Right.
And that's,
as opposed
Robin,
to what?
As opposed to every other fucking comedian?
As opposed to what, alternative comedy?
Yeah, that's no. Jamie. if you're defending, that's one of the shittiest.
No, no, I'm not saying
you're defending it because he's addicted
saying Robin Williams is a joke thief.
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay, so we have Robin, but Dane no. Still Dane no?
It's still Dane no.
Let's hear the third one.
Hold on.
Treat yourself to my material. Number three.
Okay, let's see.
Treat yourself.
Wait, Ari, what was your thought?
These are two.
Wait, we got to get him to do it now, right?
All right, let's hear it.
Hold on a second.
Jeremy,
can you do me a favor and just say treat yourself?
Treat yourself. What did I say? What did I do?
Nothing.
Why are you picking on me now already?
Well, yeah,
you sound like a guy we know.
Buddy, listen.
You just sound like someone we know.
One more bit, buddy.
Someone that I... Whatever. All right, here's the third
example.
Someone
took your material?
Another one. No, I jumped on his cake one day.
Uh-oh.
After he said, treat yourself.
Uh-oh.
All right, here's the third example. First, Louis C.K., the bit is called Itchy Ass.
And I had an itchy asshole for like a week. And I could have won $1 million. I still would have been going, fuck my asshole! It itches! I wanted to like eat bad food so I would like fart to scratch it. That's how itchy it was.
Oh, that's a damn funny bit.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Yeah. My asshole, it itches.
We're going to do that one on the radio Monday when we have a different audience. And here's Dane Cook a few years later.
The other day, I don't know if you've ever gotten this, it was about 2:30 in the afternoon, I got the itchiest asshole I've ever gotten. On record. Oh, it's the worst, isn't it? Oh, you feel, usually you're at work or someplace that you can't focus on it, you gotta do some other activities, right? And the entire day, you just kinda bounce around and try to shake it out. Right? Oh, man.
Just rewriting material, man.
Here's the deal. Here's the question, Jamie. These are three bits from a Louis C.K. HBO special that all three bits appeared on Dane Cook's CD 4 years later.
Okay. Now,
that's
you telling me...
Wait a minute. You think it's even possible that he stole...
Wait.
Is it possible?
Let me finish what I'm saying.
Okay, but just answer that question first. Is it possible?
I don't know. I don't... personally, I don't think he's that type of person. He's not that type of person, buddy. He's not a person.
Buddy, he is.
He's not a thief.
Okay.
Hey. You said Louis C.K., he get an itchy asshole, and Dane, he would never have an itchy asshole. Maybe he never...
That's what we're saying. That's exactly what we're saying. He got us right.
I was going to say it.
Buddy, itchy asshole happened to everyone. I have itchy asshole right now.
Right now.
My ass is itching.
So I can't say anything. My ass is itching because...
I want to yell nigger because...
That's not...
Enough of that word.
I gotta say one
bucks.
Thing, man. Jamie is punching his way out of the corner. You gotta give him some credit.
Yeah, he really is.
Fucking swinging blind, bro.
Oh, yeah.
He had.
It's like one of those old school fights where it's like 98 rounds.
Right. You are 100% right that people will always be jealous of successful comedians and they always wish that upon themselves. But you're 100% wrong that happens with every comedian. That's not the case with Chris Rock. It's not the case with Dave Chappelle. It's not the case with Dave Attell. There's a lot of very, very successful, very funny, very famous comedians that no one ever says a word about them stealing material.
Seems like Dice and Kinison both were accused after they became huger than huge.
Thank you.
Of
thank
stealing
you.
Stuff.
Thank
never
you.
Kinison being accused.
No?
No, Kinison accused Dice of one bit. There was a bit that, Kinison used to do a bit about gays. I don't know. How does one guy look at another guy's hairy ass and find love? How's that happen?
Yeah.
And then Dice did a bit. How does one guy, see another guy's hairy ass? And it was a very similar thing.
Right.
They'd work together. Who knows? But it was really like one.
And I was in a club the time they start fighting, they start punching each other in the face. And I try to separate them because of, again, people that come close to each other. If you know a person, if I know Dane, as long as I know him 12 years or 13 years, he is not that type of person stealing. So maybe they're close. knows, but he's not that type of person.
Why have so many people say he does for like 10 years? Why is that?
I have no idea, because of you. Maybe the people, they don't know him.
Jamie,
I know
three
him.
Bits
Jamie.
From the same guy from the same HBO special.
All right, listen,
special.
We're not going to solve this year.
Yeah, we are not. No,
we
no.
do have a plane to catch at 1:30.
I like it, though.
Jamie Masada has a club, another version of the Laugh Factory here in New York, right?
Yes, sir.
42nd Street. It's actually got a really cool vibe. It's over Showworld. Which is a really, it's like a lot of the same interior was kept, like the fucking lights, and it's really a cool place to go, man. I got a cringe.
Whites only, though. Whites only.
Absolutely.
That's right.
Who's at the Laugh Factory in New York here?
Why you guys, are you brought me in here, roast me, or are you trying to pick on me? What did I do wrong to you guys?
I was under a misconception,
I really, I love comics, I love everybody, I love Joe, I love everybody in here. You know? I mean,
you gotta understand the Opie and Anthony show.
I love you guys too. I listen to you guys all the time.
I love you too, man.
My buddy Tony Vodetka called me.
The show, Jamie. Like when you listen to this show, what's your favorite bit?
Yeah. The time that all of you guys comedians are on it, I love that
very
show.
Generic. Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Very generic.
Yeah.
Right.
Name really
one
Hollywood.
Thing we've done.
Said what?
Name one bit we've
signature
done.
Signature bit.
One signature bit.
I mean, for example, the stuff you do all of the time you do.
Oh, my God.
No, Wait. The time you were in another station you were doing. I was getting in Los Angeles, was getting a whole thing about you guys putting competition, sex stuff, was going the guy having it in church and all of that stuff.
It's
Impression O&A Party Rock.
Does that
mean anything?
O&A Party Rock?
Yeah.
Do you know what WOW is?
Yes.
What is it?
Wow.
W-O-W.
What is wow?
Yeah, wow. It has something to do with our show.
Yeah.
Wow.
Right. Well, we just started.
We don't do it that much.
So, yeah.
We don't do it that much.
You might recognize it as Flash Friday.
Okay.
Speaking of ripping off, don't
even get Flash Friday?
Yeah.
Fucking Likas.
That stupid Tom Lickass.
Anyway.
Who's at the club this week in New York?
Everybody. Good con. Okay.
Everybody.
I mean, I don't want all of the seven stars.
Michael Richards?
Michael Richards? Yeah, no, because you guys, you all.
Name one comic who's there, I know.
For example, hey.
Jamie,
just say Michael Richards is going to be there.
Dan Cook is my friend, buddy.
Yeah. Jamie could be, you could be the president. You could be the fucking president. I can see you at a podium getting asked a question and just fucking going like.
If you want
to, when are we getting out of Iraq? It's a big country.
Did you say
Ari
Spears?
Yeah.
Tremendous thief.
Oh, here we go. I knew if I said
only guy
anybody
out of the
I said he's going to
That's not true. That's not true. I'm a huge supporter of comedians. It's not true.
Yeah.
Ari Spears is a thief.
And you know what he is, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Former cast member of MAD.
That's right.
Yeah, and he worked with Damon Wayne right now on his new show.
You know what Damon Wayne's is? A brother of other Damon Wayne's, Wayne's brothers.
Mm-hmm. What the fuck?
Excuse me.
What are you guys doing to me?
All right, listen, we got to wrap up.
I should have just said nigger.
Oh, man.
R. Nelson. What do you say, Jamie? Say it once,
buddy,
just for old time's sake.
Say it
what
time.
Shall I say?
Bigger.
The word.
Say bigger. Person.
Bigger.
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 Yeah.
Okay, guys, you picked on me now.
Now say
nickel.
No. No.
And we will edit that together.
All right, guys, you're great. Thank you very much.
Jamie,
say I love
no
you guys.
Hold on, let me wrap this up. Yeah. Jamie, before you come back on the show, you got to do a little research. You got to understand our show. You don't listen to our show, which is fine.
You're a busy guy.
No,
but don't forget.
I'm working at the 2:00, 3:00 in the morning.
Yeah,
that's fine.
You know, I mean, you got to look at this.
In L.A., get an XM. Listen for a couple weeks, and then we're going to test you.
Why don't we get Jamie an XM? We can get Jamie Masada an XM.
Let's get him an XM.
Next time I'm in here, you test me
everything. We have one for him, then?
Because we're very sharp here, right, Jamie. We know when people are like kind of...
Okay, don't get on my case, please, guys. I'm going to do it.
One of the best clubs in L.A., if not the best club. Beautiful fucking club, the Laugh Factory. Badass place. Once he gets rid of all the hacks, it'll be a real good place to
work. Hey, hold on. And we backed you up on your N-word ban, even though I don't theory like it, but I know why you did it.
I backed him up on it.
For that reason.
Jamie's always been cool to me. I've been performing. Right.
Jamie, just try to banish from my car.
All right. Yeah, good luck.
All right, drive home.
Opie, what do you got? You going to the phone or something?
Yeah, we have to because it was a very busy day. We're almost forgetting that we did the eggnog drinking contest today.
Yes.
Pat won it again this year.
Yes, he did.
Set a new record, 75 double shots of eggnog. We did the baby bird. And we got our own Sam that we sent home early on the phone.
Hi, Sam.
Sam, what's up?
I got the video. It's compressing now, and it'll be up in YouTube in 15 minutes.
Oh, all right, here's the problem with the video, though, because, I mean, with YouTube, it's going to hang out for about 24 hours before it's available in the regular search.
Put a link up on opieandanthony.com, and then we'll put one on Whackbag and put one on other message boards, and it'll be great.
And everyone also, they could search it out by just searching out your account, OA Videos.
Yep, that's the username, OA Videos.
All one word, OA Videos. But the first video clip and many more from the eggnog drinking contest are going up as we speak to Sam.
Spread like wildfire.
Yeah, you guys, help us out on this one. Let's make this really viral. I don't think it's going to have much of a problem, but let's really push this one.
No, I think the puking on the face.
Hey, where's that? You show Jamie that picture from Pat. Yeah. He wasn't over at Free FM.
This is what happened today. The pictures are
a real photo.
The pictures are up on OpieAndAnthony.com.
A guy throwing up on another guy. That's eggnog.
Throwing up in his mouth.
Oh my God! I saw it from the other room.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Fantastic.
Isn't it? It's almost beautiful. Yeah. It's almost beautiful.
It's art. It is beautiful.
That is artwork.
Is Sam is going to be working on video clips all weekend long. So thank you, Sam.
Can I do something? Can I plug something?
Absolutely.
LaughFactory.com. Go see Joe Rogan. Go see everybody. They are wonderful guys. I love all of the comedians.
We love you. Jamie.
You know, it's just, please, don't put me on the spot like that, Joe.
Jamie's a good guy.
Love you guys.
One in Los Angeles, and to support the Laugh Factory here in New York on 42nd Street, it really is a cool club.
When he said, can I plug something, I was going to hand him a fork.
We all just get along.
I was a little confused, that's all.
All that shit could be stopped, though, if you just stop hecklers. That's what people need to do.
Yeah, you got to stop hecklers.
That was quick.
And ban the video phones there, Jamie.
Yeah. I have a band that they cannot
Don't
come
you
in.
Dare ban
No,
them.
They have a sign in the club, you cannot videotape.
Yeah. Yeah. Those people can't read signs.
And Jamie, I will end with this. I have been your club, and I love your club in L.A.
I'd love to have you back again.
I love your club in L.A.
Thank you, sir.
It is a good place for comedy, okay?
Thank you.
Joe Rogan, Caroline's all weekend long.
Holla.
Videos up on opieandanthony.com and YouTube. You know, do what you can with those videos, guys.
I will be in West Palm Beach Monday and Tuesday broadcasting. Tomorrow night's a bake sale. And what are we doing there? Bringing on bands and shit?
Yeah, it's just a hangout.
Yeah, okay. We get up on stage, bring on some bands.
I got to go home and fucking pack, man.
No shit. I don't even know if I'm going to make the plane.
I'm at the Improv, Ontario, California.
Bye, everyone.
Wait, Bill Burr, what?
The Improv, Ontario, California.
All right. By the way, line of the day, sponsored by BodogFight.com. Log on and watch American fighters battle for the right to represent the U.S. in a bout against the Russians. It's all on BodogFight.com. Here's today's line of the day. Next time we talk, we'll be live from West Palm Beach.
Yeah. Here comes Line of the day.
He's just drinking now. He's up to 76.
Uh-oh, here we go.
Here it goes.
Oh, God.
The baby bird is going down.
The baby bird is happening.
The baby bird is happening. Oh my god!
I almost wet myself. I swear to you, I'm laughing so hard.
We lost Jimmy. He's laughing so hard he ran into the corner.
Down goes Pat.
He's wearing puke blackface.
That was the greatest moment in radio history, period. Yeah, it's impossible to top that.
Yeah, there's no top.